Got your engines and cool your wings.
Remember, make it to the telephone. Los Angeles.
You may know for Virginia died 1-4-10-09. Telephones back home, this is the promised land called Pinnacle Boys on the line.
All right, all right, all right, all right. Degrees outside, 48 degrees.
We'll get up to another 30 degrees before the end of the day.
Is that right? Is it 70 today?
Oh, yeah.
He would send us at the terminal gate.
A swinging old chariot come down, ease the taxi to the terminal zone. Touch your engines and cool your wings.
And let me make it to the telephone. Los Angeles.
You're in Norfolk, Virginia, tied water for 1009.
Come on, King.
Hey, the poor boys on the line.
All right, we are glad you're with us this morning. As I mentioned, it's 48 degrees. Not as cold as it was yesterday. Still nippy. Because, Roger, we are in the... is the March equinox and the spring equinox. I'm not sure. I'm going to have to get you to help me figure those out.
Well, we'll
have both.
Somebody. Yeah, you're telling me we're going to merge equinoxes?
I think so. Josh, are you familiar with equinoxes?
The equini, right?
Equini. Very nice. Yeah, I looking through my notes and like, wait a minute. Can it be the March equinox and the spring equinox today?
Well, you know, two things can be right. We have discovered that. So today, of course, will be the first full day of spring.
Yeah, that was my question. Is today the first full day of spring?
It is. It is the first full day of spring. And how fitting is 48 degrees. But Roger says it's going to be 70 today, huh? Very nice.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be nice. It's going to be
really
nice.
It's a beautiful day. Listen, your grass is coming up. Listen, if you've got if you don't have any lawn taken care of, anybody take care of your lawn, get over to Sanders Greenwich. They're the best at it. And they're sprouting, bro. It's sprouting up.
Yeah, it almost makes me I get a little anxious when it's like, because, you know, it's, oh, my gosh, got to get that done. Got to get a cut.
You don't have any.
I do have enough that has to be. It's weed eating for the most part. It's a little
in the back.
Don't you have up front? Yeah, got a little bit, not much.
You have anything up there? You still have the trees up or anything?
No, nothing like that. Which is good, low maintenance.
That's fantastic, low maintenance. It's almost Hot Springs Village low maintenance. if you had rock in your entire backyard, okay, so you got nothing. Oh, very good. Yeah, so it makes you anxious. Okay,
we're just seeing it start to get, you know.
You'll start seeing the sprinkler systems and all that stuff.
Today, Wednesday hump day, no Trey Reed today. Normally we have him. I think he's, everybody's skiing right now. Everybody seems to be skiing a spring break.
My neighbors, I think I saw on the Facebook that one of my neighbors who didn't ask me to watch his house this time.
Is he skiing?
I saw him on the slope somewhere. At least they were in snow gear.
That's where Justin and the gang are. They're skiing somewhere, but we will have Craig O'Neill. I mentioned on Facebook the Lips of Legend. Yeah. Lips of Legend. Craig O'Neill brought to you by Petty Jean Meats. We'll have him in the 7 o'clock hour. RJ Hawk stopping by, brought to you by Natural State Wholesale. Hannah Gammel will be with us, brought to you by UMS Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Another home run for her.
Yeah.
What were our nicknames? I was trying to think. Hangam.
Hangam.
What was the home run, Josh? Yeah, you remember?
Hannah Slamma.
Yeah, that's it.
Is it Slamma Hammer or something? No, I don't know.
Was it?
It was something.
Hannah Slam. No.
Hannah Homer? Was it Hand Slam?
Hannah Homer?
Homer Hannah?
Homer Hannah? Hand Glam?
I think Hand Glam was there, right? I think Hand Glam. Wasn't Hand Glam?
We're missing. That,
yeah, there was.
It's a home.
There was like Hannah Montana related.
No,
well,
was, yeah.
Yeah, but it's, you know, there's a home run related. Well, he's.
Somebody out here knows.
Somebody. Well, she's got 7 home runs now. She's second on the team. She's not hitting for average, but. She's hit for power. She's on the cover of the latest Hogs Illustrated, Roger. Yeah. And I didn't realize they're still printing that. I'm going to get that. But I'm also featured in there. Clay Henry did a story on me, like, where are they now? Hannah, I said, we share the magazine. You get the cover. I get something that nobody wants to read. Everybody wants to read about you, not me. But anyway, she'll be coming up a little bit later in the show. We'll also play Match Game, brought to you by Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse. Appreciate Chris and Donnie. Sponsoring that. Also, too, several things to get to today, Roger. By the way, too, we were at the trivia last night, Josh, so we saw basketball going on, and the Democrat Gazette now has a new, you know, I get a lot of my information each morning from the Democrat. They've changed formats, and it just completely screwed me up today. You can't copy and paste. Not really happy about it, Dim Gas.
Really?
Not happy about it.
Oh, what are you talking about?
I don't know if it's user error or they have changed it where you can't do that. So what happened last night in the play-in games? You know, we were hoping maybe we could get there, or the Trojans or Red Wolves. Nobody there. So what happened last night?
We had Wagner beating Howard.
Wagner beating Howard.
71-68.
Okay.
And then this was the big one last night. So Colorado State is a 10 seed. UVA is a 10 seed.
Virginia.
Virginia,
who
yes.
won the national championship. 2019. Wow, boy, you know they
they got hammered.
By 30 or something.
67-42.
What's up with that?
A lot of people were upset that they got in the tournament, and this performance was not. There are a lot of frustrated people and teams out there. That did not.
They didn't. Yeah, they shouldn't have.
And also, their style of basketball is not fun to watch.
Same coach. He's not in trouble. They're still. He's still doing fine.
No, he's fine. But yeah. They've had a run of recent really bad tournament exits, and they just don't play exciting basketball at all.
So it's Wednesday. So then everything. The big first day is tomorrow, right?
Yeah, we've got two more games tonight.
Yeah, we got to hear that. What? It's say it again. So it starts tomorrow.
There's two games tonight.
Okay.
Two more games. First four games.
There it is.
Grambling is playing, I forget who, the 16 seed game. And then Boise State and Colorado are playing, two 10 seeds playing. And then the real deal is on Thursday.
Roger, it's just so much more fun. It's so much more fun when we know what time it is. We're going to be watching. We're telling you, Oakland's happening when, you got Oakland going on over there, too.
Well, it's always a good part. You're stuck with the Dallas Cowboys. I think you look a gift horse in the mouth. The Cowboys blowing for the last 26 of a quarter of a century plus. I can watch NFL. I can watch playoffs and Super Bowl without anything. Same thing with this year's tournament. I'm going to watch because with Wagner and Howard, I think you both agree with me. When those two teams get together, you throw out the record book. Okay,
I
don't even want to see it. Don't even open it. But I'm going to be able to watch some of those games, and that'll be great because, again, the first four-day weekend, the first 2 weeks of an NCAA tournament, some of the best because you get to see these teams like this. And, of course, we lived in an era now where a 16 seed has beaten a number one, so things are different now.
I'm looking at some of the Sledgehanna. Sledgehanna.
I like that one a lot.
Yeah, Hannah Slamma Gamma. Hannah Slamma Gamma. Somebody says y'all are a day behind. Spring equinox was yesterday.
Maybe.
Well, it's sort of debated. Our services, a lot of them say it's March 20th. It's yearly on March 20th. But spring started. You said, Roger. I said yesterday spring began, but you said you only get a couple of hours.
That's right. You only got a couple of hours when that happens. So.
I want to wish a happy birthday to JK, who turned 70.
Hey, happy birthday, JK.
But back to your point, Roger, about this is the time of year where you'd like to have a team in it.
Yeah.
And so if you're not, what I do, Roger, is that a lot of times I will just wait. Give me to the last 3 minutes and tell me if the high seed or the lower seed has
no
a
doubt.
Chance. Yes.
You go quad box. Even YouTube TV has got some new things that are happening right now for if you're a YouTube TV subscriber with that. You can put it in the quad box. You can watch some of those things. You can even have some background. But I'm like you.
It's
like watching Josh and I were talking about it, watching the last 5 minutes of a female workout video. That's all you really want to see.
Exactly.
You want to see the sweat you were talking about. So it's the same thing here. You want to watch some of those games. Those are great. And again, everybody turns into the fan of the underdog when it happens, no matter who you are. Yeah.
Also, new this year, you can watch the games on Max.
HBO Max.
Yeah,
is that right?
Yeah,
I did not know that.
All of Turner's stuff is now on Max.
Really?
You can watch there, yeah.
Well, it was because of that when we used to go watch the, and I think UALR. Was in several of them back then, some of the playing games. Is how we found out about True TV, remember?
Yeah, that's right.
Back in the day.
Basically, Guys and Practical Jokers, and then every day.
No, that's right.
Tournament time.
What was the other show?
There was a pawn shop.
The Detroit pawn shop.
Detroit pawn and 8 Mile, I think it was.
They would do these really good commercials. It was like True TV Awareness Week. And they would always run these commercials about it, and very self-aware, funny.
But absolutely. Yeah.
A couple weeks each year, we realize it.
Somebody said my angle's not good. I thought I had that thing fixed. Right? While he's doing that, is that Josh Vader talking? Is no one going to mention that? We've mentioned it. Not only do we have the March
Equinox
and the spring, we have the voice box.
Yeah, it is
the voice box.
It's the Josh box.
He's having trouble with the changing of the seasons.
It happens.
Somebody said technically the spring equinox started last night. That's what you were sort of referring to, maybe at 10 o'clock or whatever.
Yeah,
or
right.
Whatever.
Whenever
so, it was. I don't know. We're in the season. We're in the spring season.
It's now spring.
A lot of equinoxes going
around. It's over. So the gopher, when did the gopher?
Equator.
How many weeks ago did the gopher say that it was going to be spring or not? I don't even remember.
I don't remember.
Yeah. Here we are already in the middle of March.
I know.
And we start the Gravely Tour next week, I believe.
I know. I saw that. Virginia went 13 game time minutes without a point last night. That is, I'm not sure if I've ever heard.
It was like 59 minutes in real time.
That is nuts. I don't think I've ever heard of anything.
Just could not score.
Hannah Slam Tana.
It might be something like
Sledge Hannah. Sledge, yeah, that's you know, Roger, you may have to do a song about that. You know, you could do a sledge, a lot of different directions to go with Hannah. Here he goes, ladies and gentlemen. This is why he makes all the big bucks.
Yeah, I just want to play.
Now on stage, the great Roger Scott.
Yeah, I just like this song.
I know it is.
What's her number?
I'll check.
Big suit.
20.
Don't you like this song?
It is fun.
You could have a steam train if you just lay down.
What's this guy's name?
Peter Gabriel.
Peter Gabriel.
Have an aeroplane.
Aeroplane.
Flying.
I always had the little of the hot ladies with
it. Sing it if you know it. Is it Slam Tana?
All you do is call me.
Hannah Bomb Kanza. No.
No. Stop it. What? Bomb Kanza. Hannah, but you know what? Great effort from the 479, but come on now.
We talked yesterday, speaking of basketball too, about Razorbacks losing their top two players. Yeah. They lost three total. Yeah. Their top rebounder and their top shooter. Well, look who they picked up also in that same day. I guess it was sometime yesterday afternoon. Izzy Higginbotham. You know who she is, Roger?
I do.
Averaged 22 points a game. Transfer from Arkansas State.
Yep. Her family started TCBY.
No, that's
not. No.
She scored at least 30 points in 7 games this season. So what does that sound like to you?
Say again.
Okay, so she scored 30 points in 7 games this season. Yeah. So here she is. She's from Batesville.
Yeah.
She goes to Arkansas State. She's putting on what a great career.
Yeah.
Guess what? Huh? Sorry, y'all. I'm headed to Fayetteville.
Not enough money.
I would think. Sure. I would think. What else would be the motivating factor there?
Maybe it was her dream to always go to Arkansas and play basketball.
I know. I'm just saying, though. Here's Arkansas State.
Yeah.
That, you know, you
and it came to you. You know, there's got to be a loyalty factor.
Yeah, and there's like no loyalty anymore. Yeah.
Well, you know what? And there's some. I always look at the one scene in the movie Ray, which you've never seen, where the guy from Atlantic Records comes to Ray and Ray tells the guy, look, ABC's offering me this. Can you match it?
Yeah.
And they said, dude, we just can't. You know, so you got to get.
Yeah,
and we talked about that with Sam Pittman.
Yeah.
Could you, you know, could what's your name? You know, can you get me this before I move on? You know what?
Yeah.
There's got to show some semblance of loyalty, but that's coming from a guy who has not been tested with his loyalty too much.
Well, here's the deal. I get it. You know, it is what it is. I just sort of, you know, golly, just whatever her reason is. Yeah. I mean, she's the star of that player. Sure. She's the star of that team at Arkansas State.
I mean, how far is Batesville from Jonesboro? Where is it?
I think it's probably
in the middle.
It's a pretty good drive because it's not an easy shot. But you know, here the two leading scorers leave Arkansas because they're probably not happy with the program or whatever. Then this young lady, who's a star of Arkansas State, goes, well, presumably, we don't know. Money.
We don't know. Yeah, yeah.
But anyway, I thought that was interesting, Roger.
Listen, who knows what she's going to do? Listen, she may not transfer.
She's a heck of a player. She must be a heck of a player.
Absolutely. And what's her classification?
I don't know. I did not see that. The other crazy story, guys. Yeah, the other crazy story is, did you see the head of the Little Rock Airport?
Yeah, talk about that
the
last
head
night,
of the Little Rock Airport what is the word term when the ATF agents come in? They serve you a
raid.
It's a raid
essentially
on the guy who's making $250,000 a year as the executive director of the Little Rock, the Clinton Airport. So the story goes on. I saw one story.
Give me some of it.
That he apparently, according to the story I saw last night, I don't know if this is true. This is what was in the story.
Yeah.
He had been getting those weapons that they collect
at the
airport
checkpoint
and selling them. The ones that they take and get
okay.
and selling them, and then also apparently allowing people to go through the checkpoints when they should not have been going through. In other words,
okay,
but the big obviously one is selling weapons Are you kidding me? You're making $250,000 at the Little Rock Airport. As head, you're going to be stupid enough to say that's not enough. I got to sell weapons. And I'll tell you, you know, and then Roger, ATF comes to his house in West Little Rock, and he fires at him.
This was at 6 o'clock in the morning, too.
He fires at him. He's like, you know, dude, who do you think you are? And so I don't know if he's in critical condition. I don't know if he's...
No, they treated... Well, this morning, the news that we ran says that his injuries, the extent of his injuries, are unknown. He was treated at the scene, and then he was taken to the hospital.
He's lucky to be alive, and you don't fire at law enforcement and would not expect to get killed yourself. So where's his head at?
He's lucky to be alive.
Yeah.
He's going to federal
So was
prison.
He letting folks... I'll have to read the story. I know you don't want to get too deep into it.
Basically, I think what it was, Roger,
I walk in with my weapon realize
we keep it.
As opposed to me taking it. Now, do you get my weapon, or can I take it outside?
Apparently, in these cases.
Put it back in my car.
Well, we've heard different cases like that.
I'd like to know that. And then the other part of it is, he is taking those, since he's the guy, he collects them, and he's selling them to individuals.
On the black market.
On the black market.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, it's like, dude, it's $250,000.
I'm looking for a couple.
So, anyway, just a bizarre story. A guy who's successful. Bizarre. Also, so before they hired him, they looked. He was fired from a previous airport for doing something wrong. So then it comes in to say, did you do your due diligence in the hiring of this guy? And I'm sure he will say,
well, I'm all for second chances.
Well,
I know.
But if it's something that looks like...
Second decision. If I stole a couple of sodas out of the break room, a little bit different than selling guns on the black market, you might look at him a little bit deeper and go, look here, here's what we're going to do. We're going to keep it. I don't know.
Bizarre story because the guy is the head of... Yeah. I mean, it just...
Well, I can only imagine that he lives in a very nice community.
Yeah.
And those folks had to be stunned. What the hell's going on? ATF, what is this, Waco?
The guy's name is Brian Malinowski.
Brian, what are you thinking, Brian? Brian got a family?
I do not know.
Yeah.
Several things today,
Roger.
Hope
he has good dental.
Several things today. It's National Proposal Day.
All right.
We always like to say, what did you do in your proposal? Anything's fun? And we'll ask Craig O'Neill that when he comes in.
Sure.
It's National Ravioli Day.
Okay.
You know, when I think of ravioli, I think of being a
Chef
kid.
Chef Boyardee.
Yeah, Chef Boyardee. Yeah. Yeah. What about you, Josh? Okay, this would be interesting.
Yeah, will be.
Ravioli, yes or no?
Gross, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, let's...
You will?
Come on.
Homemade?
Oh, no,
homemade?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, so,
okay.
So, Chef,
oh, yeah.
Chef Boyardee?
No.
No, that is Little Caesars for
that's
him.
That's what I was expecting.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll say, so, I actually do enjoy, like, the one thing I really do enjoy, toasted ravs. It's not real ravioli.
Yeah, I like that, yeah.
Mainline Sports Bar.
Yeah, they have
good
them.
Ones.
Yeah. Bruno's has them, too. Bruno's is outstanding,
May she rest in peace. My Aunt Mary, she made...
Your aunt?
Yes, Aunt Mary.
Aunt Mary. And whatever. She made homemade ravioli.
Okay. Well, that has to be, obviously, but you would not lower yourself to go and get a Chef Boyardee.
No, I'm not, no.
Can I tell you, Roger, you can eat, as a bachelor, you can eat ravioli cold right out of the can. It is outstanding.
My man over here, listen. Married man, too.
You're going to get a paper cut, and you're going to get an infection.
Roger, it's also National Alien Abduction Day. Remember, you know, what's the most famous movie alien induction? I'll give three, two,
you're talking about,
one.
Yeah, of the third kind.
I don't remember the details of that movie. I'm just thinking of I'm Back. Does that give you any hint?
What? That's not alien induction.
He'd been abducted by aliens, and he said, I'm
back. I thought you were talking about Poltergeist. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, remember?
Absolutely. Independence Day.
Independence Day.
Yes,
what
I'm
was that
sorry,
character's
Randy
name?
Randy Quaid.
Yeah,
he said,
I'm back.
Right,
nobody believed him.
No, he's a nut job.
Yeah,
absolutely.
And remember, there are people out there that said they've been abducted, and they're pretty elaborate.
Who's the family? the husband and wife who gave pretty good detail back in the 50s.
Oh, did they?
Oh, yeah, yeah. They were abducted, and they talked about the probing. Yeah, there's some of those things. Absolutely.
Probing.
Yeah.
It's also
you believe in that? You
national,
believe in that at all?
No.
All, yeah.
No,
any
no, no.
you No, not about it, but do you believe there's life out there?
It could be, but
I asked you if it could be. Do you think so?
I would lean towards not.
Okay.
You know there's life out there somewhere else on some other planet?
I've been on this planet for 60 years, right. And everybody ultimately finds out stuff.
It's a long time in alien life.
Yeah, and the fact that we still can't have anything of substance other than fake stuff. Showing.
But you don't think like some other galaxies?
Well, I would just say show me evidence. Give me some evidence. I'm open to it.
It's a massive universe.
We've got the most powerful,
telescope.
Yeah, it can see billions of stars away. Yeah. And we
let's be honest, our government is corrupt enough. They're not going to show some of this stuff. But that's why we need an actual Space Force Star Trek ship. Get out there and go.
Yes.
To where no man has gone before. Find out and see if there are green chicks with horns on their head.
I know. We thought we were making progress in space and things have sort of slowed down.
They really have.
We can't even have our colony on the moon. We thought we could have that 20 years ago.
Right, exactly. Ridiculous. Come on.
It's National Macaroon Day. Do you know what a macaroon is?
A macaroon?
Is that what you say, macaroon?
It's a cookie, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a cookie deal. We're all popular in Europe, but not as much over here. I'm okay with it.
Coconut?
They got different flavors. Roger, it's World Frog Day.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I used to have a fish tank with
a frog. I think frogs are creepy.
It was tiny, 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 tiny. You know, they're part of the dinosaur family.
Yeah, yeah. We had a good time at the zoo yesterday.
Sure
by the way,
did.
Thank you. Won't you be my neighbor day today? It's National Won't You Be My Neighbor. Why is that, Roger?
It's got to be because of Mr. Fred Rogers.
Yes, Josh. Did you ever watch Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood?
Did not.
Yeah,
I thank AETN and PBS for all the things that we grew up watching. I was not a tremendous, I don't want to say fan, I was not a viewer of Mr. Rogers.
Yeah, I wasn't either.
There's other shows
that I
watched.
A bit younger for us, I think.
Was it?
I think so.
I don't know.
We never connected
when
to it.
When did he start?
I'll go back and look at the notes on that. In 1968.
Okay.
So in the 70s, by the time it sort of became popular.
Well, we were five when he started.
So
10 years later, we were 50. Yeah, so it kind of missed. I was still a teenager.
We went Cat the Kangaroo.
Yeah, our Adam's apple dropped.
It's also National Bibliomania Day. I'm not going to tell you what that is. Bibliomania Day. I'm going to save that for Craig when he comes in here. It's also the National Cherry Blossom Festival. As a man who appreciates his yard,
yeah,
you go to D.C. and they got those cherry blossoms around.
And
there.
Who there's gave
a,
them to
a,
us?
That's
who?
Right. There's a great story.
Yeah,
and I think the majority of them that were there originally are not there. They had to replant them, and I think there are two of the original.
The
Japanese.
Yeah,
I was thinking that was it. Yeah. So anyway, and plus got some great birthdays today, Roger. We got as I mentioned Fred Rogers, but Jerry Reed. Jerry Reed, one of my.
You kidding me?
Josh, Jerry Reed is. How would you, when you would start with him, would you start smoking the Bandit first? He was Burt Reynolds' buddy.
Yeah, he was one of those sessions players.
But
he could
play, Amos Moses.
Oh, yeah.
When you're hot, you're hot. Yeah. She got the gold mine, I got the shaft.
That's right.
He wrote Guitar Man for Elvis.
That's right.
Let's see, what else was there? Of course, he was it's probably him playing.
You can watch it. He has fun. If you go to somebody, just look up YouTube, Jerry Reed. Some of these songs are like top of the charts.
I know.
He was back when Fred Rogers started.
He was fun.
Very fun.
We'll go to break with this.
Come on now.
Finally, they threw up their hand and said, when you hot, you hot. I say, yeah. When you're hot, you're hot. When you're not, you're not.
Coach Kevin Kelly joins The Zone each Wednesday, presented by the Woodrock Athletic Club. The indoor pickleball facility is now open. First tournament is April 5th through the 7th.
This is SportsCenter.
March Madness officially began last night with a pair of games at the First Four in Dayton. In the West region, it was 16 seed Wagner over 16 seed Howard, 71-68. Wagner will now take on North Carolina, who's the number one seed in the West. And then in the Midwest, it was Colorado State 67, UVA 42. The Rams will now take on number 7 seed Texas on Thursday. Two more games coming tonight in Dayton. First, it's Grambling in Montana State at 5:40 on True TV. Then at 8:10, it'll be 10 seed Colorado and number 10 seed Boise State. The first round will begin officially on Thursday. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Continuing to warm up across Arkansas, 75 today, mostly sunny. Could be a couple of showers or thunderstorms in North Arkansas. And tonight's low drops down to 50. Better rain chances statewide arriving for Thursday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Hey folks, Trey Johnson here with HJ Trailer Sales in Hot Springs. Spring is coming and everyone is getting ready to get outside. So if you need your trailer serviced or repaired, let us help you out. Or you may be needing a trailer to get your golf cart to the golf course. Or you need a trailer for work. Or if you just need to buy a new trailer for recreational use. Let us help you at HJ Trailer Sales with one of the best service departments in the state. Visit us in Hot Springs or check us out on Facebook or at hjtrailersales.com.
Hey, Wilson, where are you heading?
Man, I'm going to see Matt Jones.
I love Matt Jones. You got Miracle on Markham. I'm talking about
that Matt Jones, the real Matt Jones, Raj.
The real Matt Jones? Oh, you mean the mortgage expert Matt Jones at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union in Benton.
That's the one.
Did you know that Matt Jones at Alcoa Community FCU is a Benton boy and a graduate of OBU? So he's very familiar with Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties.
Yep.
Did you know that in addition to being a mortgage lender expert, Matt Jones is also a licensed realtor who can give you insight into both sides of your mortgage transaction?
I did.
So, go see Matt Jones at Alcoa Community FCU for all your mortgage needs. And if you're looking at buying a new home or need to refinance the home you're already in, the real Matt Jones at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union is your guy. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union serving all of Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties. For more information or to apply securely online, go to alcoacommunityfcu.org. And remember, with the real Matt Jones, miracles can still happen.
Is your Oaklawn Thoroughbred racing action so close you can feel it? Or is it the view from your trackside luxury suite? However you like it, racing season is off and running at Oaklawn, with live races every weekend through May 4th. It's fun by the furlong all season long. Make your reservations today at oaklawn.com. What's your Oaklawn? Gambling problem? Call 1-800-522-4700.
Calling all coaches. Summerwood Sports in Bryant. It's your go-to destination for basketball and volleyball tournaments, practices, and more. Conveniently located off Interstate 30, it's the premier sports complex in Central Arkansas. With up to 4 courts and 2 gyms, Summerwood Sports is perfect for training sessions, team practices, and even epic birthday parties. Check availability and learn more at summerwoodsports.com. Elevate your game at Summerwood Sports.
Want to see our beautiful faces? Catch Morning Mayhem streaming live every day on YouTube, X, and Facebook. Just search 1037 The Buzz.
Yes, sir, honey. It happened on one of them zippity-doo-dah days. Now, that's the kind of day when you can't open your mouth without a song jump right out of it.
Zippity-doo-dah. Ah, there we go.
My, oh my, what a,
you know what? After our conversation off the air, I need this to bring me right back.
Yes. My way. Zippity doo dah.
Come on.
Mr. Bluebird is on my shoulder.
It's the truth.
It's factual.
Everything is satisfactual.
Zippity doo dah.
Zippity a. Song of the South.
Wonderful feeling. Wonderful.
There you go,
that
Justin.
One, okay, 76 years ago on this day, 1948, Zippity-Doo-Dah won the best original song at the 20th Academy Awards. Wow, how about that?
You know, listen,
what
those cats,
song
they
wrote,
oh, they,
oh, yeah, great stuff.
They all did. Yeah.
Also, the guy who played Kris Kringle in Miracle on 34th Street won Best Supporting Actor on
that
day.
Is that Best Supporting?
Yeah. Well,
really?
Yeah, but he was great, too.
Yes. What would give me his initials? Do you have them?
Edward. Oh, I'm sorry. Edmund.
Yeah.
Gwynn.
Yeah. Okay.
Several things. Someone says, watch Men in Black last. This is our Southern Structural Solutions text line. Watch Men in Black last night. I didn't realize in the tunnel scene they are playing an Elvis A-track of y'all's intro song, Promised Land.
Yeah.
It's pretty funny how calm Tommy Lee Jones is.
Driving
I couldn't
car,
remember
yeah.
that's what they played.
Yep.
I knew there was an Elvis song. Somebody said Fire in the Sky would be the best alien abduction movie.
Don't know.
I've not seen that one. Josh, you may have.
Know.
I don't know. Flight of the Navigator. I don't know anything about this, that one either. I don't know if that's an alien or not, alien abduction movie. Here's one. Harold Jr., Mr. Malinowski, actually makes $264,000 in salary, not $250,000. I was sort of rounding off. I knew it was in that ballpark. Yeah, plenty of money. Someone says, tell Josh there's a remake of Roadhouse starring Conor McGregor coming out Thursday on Amazon Prime. So that's by, which, you know, I think is interesting. I wonder how that would have done at the theaters. I thought, you know.
I would guess not well.
Say it's true.
You what? Cannot replace Ben Gazzara with Conor McGregor.
Well,
Ben Gazzara didn't play him, but I know what you're saying. Yeah.
Who plays Ben Gazzara in the new one? Who plays the character of Ben Gazzara, the bad guy?
I don't know if there is. I think Conor McGregor is the heavy, though.
Well, he is in this movie.
He's the heavy.
Think
he's taking on two roles?
Well, I think he's the bad. Well, I don't know.
Because I guess
he will stand out.
Who is the guy who
the fighter? Him? Listen, Acri, I think, has had the fighter on their show.
Acri says no.
That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Was it?
It's not a recognizable name that everybody knows.
Well, Terry Funk was in there too.
He was, but yeah, it wasn't Terry Funk. Remember, Roger? We thought that Acri had that guy.
But Acri said no.
It wasn't him.
Yeah, well, I think he is.
I don't know who plays the
lead. I think we know more about Acri than he does.
Well, first of all, the guy who plays the lead is no Patrick Swayze. All right, I like the guy, but he's no Patrick Swayze.
I do too,
but he's no Patrick.
Conor McGregor as Knox. Look up. While I've got it on here, Josh, look up the cast of the 1989 Roadhouse. And tell me.
Do they use the same names?
So, I don't know. Because okay. I don't see. Huh?
Sam Elliott, Kelly Lynch, Ben Gazzara.
Sam Elliott.
But who was Ben Gazzara's character? What was it?
Brad Wesley.
Brad Wesley.
Yeah, I don't see Brad Wesley on here.
Small town terrorist, yeah, Brad Wesley.
I think they changed the names for him.
I thought he was the best part of the movie, to be honest.
He was great. No, yeah. And I'll tell you, McGregor is good. Roger, you saw he's fun to hate. He's a fun, hateable character. Yeah.
There's some questions comes about on tomorrow. How well his personal life is going right now.
Is that right?
Yeah,
I have not heard that.
He's done for the movie. And look, I don't know anything about him as an actor, but typically they don't do great. So.
Well, all I know is this is Jake Gyllenhaal, yeah.
I saw a scene last night. Who is Lucas Gage? I saw him on a show I watched before I went to bed last night when I got home from trivia. Lucas Cage. He plays one of the guys.
White Lotus.
I don't know him. Do you know him? He's one of the guys that's one of the workers in the bar that Jake Gyllenhaal works with. That says, "Hey, go up there and hit this guy." Yeah.
Pigskin did not mean a remake.
I don't think so either. Pigskin said that Roger could play the Ben Gazzara role. You could do that.
I could because I'm typecast
He is a good jerk in that movie.
Thank you. And I think I could play. I'd love to play a good jerk.
In Antiquities, you're a great jerk.
I'm a great jerk.
Although there's a twist at the end.
Even the Grinch's heart grew three feet.
Hey, what's crazy, Josh? In the movie Antiquities at Roger's Inn, the first showing of that had a different ending than what they end up going to the final release, right? Because so there's a scene at the end with Roger that's not in the, and it just almost gets you choked up.
It makes you think about that. It makes you want to go to Antiquities, the prequel. And find out again where me and Basil, we were going at each other at the beginning of the movie. But if you go to the prequel, we grew up together, and so we have a history in the prequel. And then what about Blundell's family? How many wives did he have? A wife? Did he have children? Maybe who knows?
So was this here?
Did test the original ending, and is that why they switched it? The test audience is not like it.
Test audience still because I killed people. I blew up the entire town.
Acri had that guy fired after Dalton caught him banging the chick in the storeroom. He's from Arkansas. What?
Well, there's one guy. I think there is. There's one guy that's. I think Acri had on one of the guys who actually. Was kin to Brad Wesley in the movie, and I think he's an actual musician. I think he was even in the movie about Jerry Lee Lewis.
Can I tell you everything about that movie? We've had this debate about Roadhouse, but there's Sam Elliott's in this movie.
It's just such a strange
and Terry
movie.
Funk's in this
well,
movie.
Like Kelly Lynch.
Kelly Lynch.
We're talking about somebody who mentioned the tall sex.
Dr. Elizabeth, right?
Yes. Uh-huh. And so, like, we were talking about Kelly McGillis and Tom Cruise the other day not having chemistry.
Yes,
I feel like Kelly Lynch is almost, like, in a different movie in this movie. Like, it feels like she is just not fit in at all. Like,
she looks the part, my friend.
She looks fantastic. Kelly Lynch
is in the new one.
No.
And the old ones? Yeah. Okay.
The doctor and the old
ones. I don't know. Listen, I saw it where it was going to be on, and I'll watch it. But I watched that movie you sent me the clip on with Ethan Hawke. I watched that. Well, I had it and watched a little bit of it.
I can't remember what that was about. I sent that to you.
Cheadle and Richard Gere the life in a week of those two guys.
Roger, I said it's World Frog Day. I'm showing you this picture of one of our listeners who sent us these. They killed 75 right. frogs. I don't know what
man's a frog hunt.
I don't know what is about frogs. They creep me out. And I used to go to my grandmother Mumsy's pond. And I would take my BB gun, and these were giant bullfrogs. I mean, these were huge. And I would hit them with a BB, and they just bounce up, and they jump in the water. And there was a movie that came out, I think it was called Frogs. And it was where the and they shot it in Florida. And the reptiles, the frogs and the turtles, they ate people.
I think maybe part of the biblical, that you might not like them for that.
That's true. That is true. Close Encounters of the Third Kind, Alien Abduction. Can I tell you, I watched that for the first time last year. I was not impressed. I was not impressed.
You didn't really?
I was like, wow.
For the time, I think it was a pretty good movie.
Yeah, 70s movie.
Yeah. The Richard Dreyfuss is so good.
I liked the beginning of it, but as the thing went on, I was like, wow, this has run out of gas for me. But it was it was popular at the time.
Oh, very popular. I mean, you know how things come in cycles. I mean, there's a bunch of that going on at one point.
The legend, Craig O'Neill, coming up in the 7 o'clock hour. We got to play a little match game. RJ Hawk, Hannah Gamble, and more. And your text, 661-1037. It's spring.
Yeah, man.
It's welcome to spring.
Come on. Ashamed, and baby, I'm not scared. I'm singing, follow me. Everything is all right. I'll be the one to tuck you in at night. And if you want to leave, I can guarantee you won't find nobody else like me. Hey, it's David Basil for Simmons Bank. You've heard me say over and over again how much I love being a Simmons Bank customer and learning about their amazing success story, starting with one little Pine Bluff bank in 1903 and now celebrating their 120th banking birthday. They have become one of the fastest growing banks in America. 120 years in banking, that's a ton of experience. The reason Simmons Bank has been around for 12 decades is because they have a track record of helping people turn their goals into plans. And that's worth repeating. Simmons Bank knows how to help their customers turn their goals into plans. And they're ready to talk to you now, but first, they'll listen. Simmons Bank will guide you at every step. No matter what's next in your life, Simmons Bank wants to make financing the easiest decision you make. A personal loan from Simmons Bank could be the solution you need for large purchases like home improvement projects, wedding expenses, vacations, emergency expenses, or an automobile, boat, or RV purchase. Don't wait any longer. Let Simmons Bank help change your financial life.
Robert Irwin Jewelers, 6 hours, 60% off sale is this Saturday from 10 to 4 only at the McCain Mall in North Little Rock location. But everything in the showcase is 60% off this Saturday, 10 to 4.
It's a legit 60% off sale. Do not miss it.
Let's talk garage doors. Your garage door. Is it too loud or letting cold and hot air in around the frame? Overhead Door Company of Little Rock will make it all better. In March only, they will perform their garage door tune-up and safety inspection for just $79. And just in March, that's just $79 for up to 3 garage doors and openers. You need this done once a year, so why not now? And just for $79. Schedule now at overheaddooroflittlerock.com.
Right now at Fort Thompson, Smith & Wesson Shield, 2.09 millimeter, $269.90. Beretta APX-A1, 9mm, $199.90 after $50 mail-in rebate. CCI 9mm brass, 50 count box, $12.99 at Fort Thompson in Sherwood.
Hello, folks. It's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge store here in Sherwood. For the past few months, we've been asking you to give us a chance to buy your cars, and the response has been great. We really appreciate all of you who brought your cars in and turned it into cash. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Folks, we're still buying cars every day. So look around and see what you or your family has in the garage that you want to turn into cash. It's really easy, folks. Just come into Fletcher Dodge and ask for Chris or Andy. We'll buy any vehicle and we'll pay you more than anyone. We can't find enough vehicles at the auto auctions to meet the demand, so we're extending you this offer to the public. We'll pay you more, so don't wait. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Come see us today for the best cash offer on your car, truck, van, or SUV. Just ask for Chris or Andy. We'll pay you more, so come see us at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood. Thanks.
Roger Scott for Gravely Mowers. You know, when it comes to beautiful lawns, nothing cuts like a Gravely. And when it comes to cutting prices, there's nothing like the Gravely Mow the Distance sales event, where you can save up to 25%. And special financing is available on America's most rugged and dependable mowers, including their ZT-HD. It's the residential mower built to commercial standards. But hurry, because the Mow the Distance sale is only through April 8th and only at your authorized Gravely dealers like MPE in Sheridan or Gravel Ridge Small Engine in Jacksonville.
Old Man Winter here. One more snowstorm.
Not a chance, Mr. Winter. It's spring.
It's also time for the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event, where you can get great deals on all our award-winning Hyundai models, all backed by America's best warranty. Hurry in. These deals won't last at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now get 0% APR on the Tucson, or pay only $369 a month with zero down payment. Now, during the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Offers end soon. Call 469-613-0227 for details.
Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse presents Match Game on Morning Mayhem. Listen for your chance to play their version of the classic TV game show. Brought to you by Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse, Arkansas's truck accessory headquarters for over 30 years. Call 501-568-0040 today or click online at arkansastruck.com.
This is Miss Arkansas Corey Keller, and you're listening to Morning Mayhem on 103.7 The Buzz.
Your anger and your hate, I think, is coming off as erratic to people.
Passion. My passion. It's all
okay,
passion.
Your passion, yes, is coming off as erratic,
right,
to people.
Right. Well, you borrow my brain for 5 seconds and just be like, dude, can't handle it. Unplug this bastard.
What, some are saying that you're bipolar.
Wow. What does that mean?
I guess that, you know, you're on two ends of the spectrum.
Wow. And then what? What's the cure? Medicine? Make me like them? Not going to happen. I'm by winning.
Oh,
I win,
gosh,
here, I win there. If I'm bipolar, aren't there moments where a guy like crashes and like in the corner, like, oh my God, it's all my mom's fault? Shut up. Shut up. Stop. Move forward.
That's that weird Charlie Sheen moment in time when it went crazy. Remember that? The whole nation was watching.
Tiger Blood thing?
Yeah, Tiger Blood.
Tiger Blood.
I don't even know the premise of why that even came to be. What happened to him? Did he thought he was on drugs or something? Or he's going to commit suicide?
Well, he was.
But why did we all of a sudden pay attention to him? Was he threatening somebody?
Well, he was
somebody?
Making tons of money on that We Three Sons or whatever they show. Yeah, 2.5 minutes.
Yeah, I know that. But
yeah, and he got into it with Lori.
Something
and
happened where...
Well, he was also dating the prostitute back
then.
Yeah,
what was prostitutes, her name? Yeah, the or porn
what
star.
What was her name? No, I think she was a head madam.
Is that what it was?
Yeah, what was her name? Well, he was dating all them, too.
Shock the monkey!
Winning.
Shock the monkey.
What was the name of her? It was Loyola Fontana. What was her name?
Hey, we've got our bracket challenge. If you have Safari, you can't find it on our website. Justin Akery, we need to look at that. I tried to find it yesterday. It works with other browsers, but not Safari, I guess.
It's so, the third tab. So
yeah.
Go past the BuzzBQ one and the one for the Buzz Golf Tournament. The third tab.
Fill it out. Fill out the bracket. There are millions that will be filling out. What did I see? A third of Americans will fill out a bracket this week?
I think Samantha has got one that she sent out to all of the boys in her family. And I thought, if I get involved, and I need to do it right away, if I get involved, I will let her put all the teams in there.
Yes.
I think just to see.
Looking at life and feedback, which we oftentimes, we spend a lot of time on the
Heidi
text line.
Fleisch, Heidi Fleisch.
Heidi Fleisch.
Remember Heidi Fleisch?
That's it. Eddie makes a great point. We are your number one sports station, yep, and sports show.
Of course.
Well, we haven't mentioned yet. Major League Baseball has begun. Right, Josh? But they're not in America. Oh, listen, America's pastime is opening their season in South Korea.
In South Korea.
Go figure. They've done that before, like in Japan, haven't they?
I'm wondering how many people know
nobody
that baseball is beginning right now.
Yeah, well, I say not nobody, but very few.
Very few.
Why would you have your opening day in South Korea? What's the purpose of it?
I was scrolling on Twitter last night, /X, right before I went to bed, and somebody tweeted, baseball regular season starts in 6 hours. And I was like, excuse me?
You didn't even know.
I had no idea.
When Josh doesn't know that kind of information, you have lost a generation.
And I'm a baseball fan. I love my Mets.
Yeah, I mean, you hadn't said a word 2 minutes that we saw that. I thought, wait a minute, surely not.
Yeah.
We used to talk. We sort of bagged on them for a while, Rogers. They've done that. They open their season on Sunday night.
Yeah.
Dude, what are you doing? You know, be smart. You know, make it be on a Saturday or something where thousands
can
pay attention.
Years, haven't they?
Yeah, they just haven't been real wise.
Well, they're, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't realize that spring ball was over. I thought people were still going down there watching them in Florida.
It's still happening today.
It is still happening.
Spring training games happening today.
How can that be? How much of a difference?
I checked the schedule. All throughout this week, and let me check again here. But if you look at today's schedule, you know, we've got a game happening right now between the Dodgers and the Padres. And at 12:05, Detroit, Minnesota will get things going in Florida.
Crazy. Josh's voice tone sounds like the actor in the Godfather series.
Which one?
I don't know.
Fredo?
I don't know.
Do I sound like John Cazale?
Someone says, David, I saw Coach at walk-ons in Little Rock yesterday. Pretty cool, from Savage. So who do we, when we say saw Coach, would you presume
Sam?
Yeah. Would you presume Muss?
I would think Sam.
Yeah. I guess Sam. If you can...
Well, we've had Darrell Walker on a bunch. Could it be Darrell Walker?
True. We've seen, saw Sam at the parade. He and his wife up on stage.
They were on stage, yeah.
Yeah. I was sitting. I mean, he wasn't performing. Yeah. Like, who else would be Coach? I do have, I had a guy named Coach that comes to trivia at Boudreaux's. We have Coach that calls. We had Coach send me a picture of me. I don't know.
I have to, Roger, I've got to get up to spring practice to watch to see the progress of this team.
Yes, you do.
People are asking. And I said, you know what? I don't want to comment yet without having seen them, because I don't want to give out false hope and false information. By the way, too, I do want to thank Clay Henry. I haven't seen it, but I am featured in Hogs Illustrated this month. It's a publication you also get online. But on the cover is Hannah Gammel. Yeah. So fitting that we get Hannah today. I texted her last night. I said, we share a publication, but nobody cares about what I've done. They care about looking at you and reading your article.
That's not true. We love Hannah. We love you, too.
Hannah, and if you missed it earlier, we were revisiting the Hannah Gammel name. And
Ryan Hill, my son-in-law, says that it was Hannah. Did we do Hannah Slamtana?
I think so.
Hannah Slammeroo?
Hannah Slamtana. Yeah. Hannah Slammer. And then we did Hang Glam
last year
with the earrings from Jones and Son.
Not Hang Glam. Ham Gam.
Ham Gam.
Hannah Glam is something.
Ham Gam.
That's a glam squad. Ham Gam.
It is spring break week this week. Hope you're having a good time with your family. Yeah. Folks are in different places. You know, we had Chris Kane said he was going up to Branson. We had with the zoo yesterday. We said, go see the zoo. Did you see when we were pulling away, Roger, how many people were walking in the zoo yesterday?
In chilly weather. Yes.
Chilly weather.
It's freezing.
It was freezing yesterday.
Absolutely.
I told Josh last night at trivia, for those who missed it, that bird that they brought in at the end was Creepo. It looked like it was an animatronic. Is what it called?
Animatronic.
Animatronic bird that you would see like in a Jurassic Park or Disney or whatever.
It had the head of a dinosaur.
It looked like a dinosaur.
Whatever that thing with that weight that
it had
on the
top. And it looked like it was 1,000 years old. It was creepy.
Do you remember the name of it? No.
But those are the kind of things you can see at the
hornbill. I think it was hornbill something. But it was. It did look like channel lock grips.
I mean, I've seen the parrot long beak, like a toucan Sam.
This was
prehistoric look.
It was prehistoric. It was pterodactyl like.
It was. Go by and see the zoo this week if you got your kids staying in town.
Absolutely. Great weather the rest of the week as well, I think. I'll look it up, but.
Someone says that you can actually watch Major League Baseball in Korea live on ESPN right now. Yeah, that is correct. That is just a bizarre. They're still practicing spring ball in America, but you kicked off your season in South Korea.
And I need to know, is there a big difference between 1,000 and 500 Mbps, the speeds? Is there that big a difference?
Between what?
On your internet and all that. Is there that big a difference between 1,000 and 500?
What does Mbps stand for?
Well, I think we know.
The legend, Craig O'Neill, coming up shortly.
He'll know.
Yes, yeah, Craig O'Neill.
The last bastion of quality programming.
Why would you listen to any other radio station than 103.7 The Buzz? KABZ Little Rock.
Roger Scott for Family Markets. Are you tired of the same old grocery store experience? Then it's time to switch things up and shop at the neighborhood Family Markets in Pangburn, Malvern, and Shannon Hills. Our stores offer a unique shopping experience where we know our customers by name and offer a wide selection of fresh, locally sourced meats and produce. And you can even grab you a hot cup of community coffee while you're there. On selected items, you can mix and match any five items for only $24.99. And if you're a Valero gasoline customer, store points on your Family Markets reward card and reduce redeem them at the pump to lower your price per gallon at select stores. At your neighborhood family markets, we're committed to providing a personalized shopping experience that's focused on our customers. So come on down and see why we're the best choice for your grocery needs. With fresh food, great deals, and friendly service, we're sure you're going to love shopping at the neighborhood family markets. So come on, stop by today and check us out. We're the family markets, with stores located in Pangburn, Malvern, and Shannon Hills. The way grocery shopping is supposed to be. Family markets.
Our guys aren't so bad, right?
This is taking unsportsmanlike conduct to a whole new level.
Well, maybe not. 103.7 The Buzz. KABZ Little Rock. Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
The executive director of the Clinton National Airport was involved in a shootout with federal agents Tuesday morning. ATF agents were performing a search warrant at 53-year-old Brian Malinowski's home in West Little Rock Tuesday morning. While serving the warrant, ATF officials say Malinowski opened fire, injuring one person. Agents fired back and injured the executive director of the airport. He and the agent were sent to the hospital for treatment. The agent had non-life-threatening injuries, while Malinowski's injuries are unknown. Many people might be concerned about their cell service when the solar eclipse happens April 8th. Cell service reps don't anticipate many issues when the eclipse happens, but there are some things to be on the lookout for. Since many are coming to Arkansas, one rep says to make sure you have the latest software downloaded on your device. And another from AT&T says when it's packed, you can move back and forth to LTE and 5G network to find internet. The networks will be monitoring the event closely. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
Brought to you by Floyd Seafood, Keel Avenue in Sherwood. It's crawfish season, and Floyd's has live Louisiana crawfish. Order by 1 p.m. Thursday for weekend boils. Floyd's, meatandseafood.com.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Continuing to warm up across Arkansas, 75 today, mostly sunny. Could be a couple of showers or thunderstorms in North Arkansas, and tonight's low drops down to 50. Better rain chances statewide arriving for Thursday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Want the latest information on bass tournaments and the best fishing spots in the state? Then listen to Fishing Arkansas Sunday mornings with Big Sarge and his crew. Fishing Arkansas is presented by shelter insurance agent Jamie Marsh, Stanley Hardware, Fletcher Auto Group, Axles Plus, and Cooper's Nursery in Cabot. Fishing Arkansas Sunday mornings on 103.7 The Buzz.
Roger Scott for Oakland Racing Casino Resort. Are you tired of feeling like a lonely raccoon in the dark? Well, say goodbye to those gloomy nights and hello to the Oakland Eclipse Festival, shining bright from April 4th to April 8th. And get ready to bask in the glow of family, fun, and affordability all weekend long. We've got you some horse racing action hotter than a jalapeno salsa, and not one, but two Mitsubishi Eclipses are up for grabs. And for all you stargazers out there, come catch the glimpse of the eclipse from our legendary Oakland infield. Tickets for the April 8th infield event are a steal at just $20. And you know Oakland's event center is cooking up some sizzle entertainment for you. Mitchell Tenpenny on Saturday, April 6th, followed by Better Than Ezra on Sunday, April 7th. And get ready to laugh, sing, and dance with Terry Fader, Gary Allen, and Aaron Lewis on various dates throughout the year. And boy, howdy, stay tuned, because we've got more big announcements and headliners coming. Snatch up your tickets and book your rooms at Oaklawn.com today. It's all happening in beautiful Hot Springs, home to Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock are opening March 27th. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor, appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more at the all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock.
Red tape. One in three businesses will get caught up in it, and they'll be penalized by the IRS for mismanaging their payroll. Because when you're handling payroll, HR compliance, and those constantly changing tax laws, that red tape can get sticky in a hurry. At The Payroll Company, we free you from that tangled mess and get you back to business. The Payroll Company. Less headaches, more than payroll. Visit morethanpayroll.com to learn more.
Here's another remarkable success story from QC Kinetics. This one from Chad, who hurt his knee at the gym one day, and it just kept on hurting for months.
From my high school football and wrestling days, I already had a little bit of damage in there, but this just sent it over the edge.
Chad tried traditional treatments with no improvement. When he turned to the non-surgical regenerative treatments at QC Kinetics.
It was really fascinating how they did their work, and the science behind it was very intriguing, and it works. Extracting the cure out of my own body blew my mind. It's like I'm brand new again. It was fantastic.
That's because the QC Kinetics natural biologic treatments use your body's own healing power to restore damaged tissue in your hips, shoulders, back, and knees, providing long-lasting relief.
Now I'm back at the gym. I'm 100%, feeling great.
If you're tired of suffering with pain from arthritis or injury, call QC Kinetics now for a free consultation.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
It's Pat Bradley for Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, where their customers are always number one. Speaking about numbers, 6% APY is still available at Alcoa. Earn up to 6% interest on your checking account balances for doing the things you already do, like using your debit card and direct deposit. You can also get your ATM fees waived. Apply today for your free Kasasa checking account and earn up to 6% APY at AlcoaCommunityFCU.org. Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union, serving Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties.
Clayton Homes of Conway is moving. But until then, you can find them at their location on East Dave Ward Drive, where you're invited to stop by on April 12th and 13th for their inventory reduction sale. Save thousands of dollars on in-stock inventory of homes, starting as low as $55,000, including free statewide delivery. Lenders will be available for all your financing questions. There'll be door prizes, food, fun, and entertainment for the whole family. April 12th and 13th at Clayton Homes at Conway.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem.
If I can change.
Live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios.
And you can change.
Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Everybody can change.
Here is David Basil, Roger Scott, and Justin Moore.
All right, 7:06 on this hump day, March 20th. About 45 degrees out there. Still a little chilly on this first full day of spring.
Yep.
March equinox, spring equinox. Craig O'Neill will be here in just a minute. I'm looking at the article that Clay Henry wrote.
Yeah,
it's embarrassing for me to read these things. I've never have felt comfortable. I don't like watching something that I've done, whether it be on camera or
you've got
writing.
Some videos.
I'm very uncomfortable.
I am too, because you can always improve.
If you want to be a part of the show, 661-1037 is the number. Craig O'Neill coming up, RJ Hawk as well, Hannah Gamble. And we got a little match game to play. Match game is brought to you by Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse. Hannah Gamble by UMS Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, RJ Hawk, Natural State Wholesale, and Petty G Meats. You know, we have, when Craig comes in, we should have a Petty G Meat breakfast sometime.
Well, I don't know why we don't. Ed Ruff, if you're out there, Wayne Cox, can we get that? Hey, thanks a lot yesterday. Great talking to Peyton Stovall.
Oh, yeah, he was outstanding. Yeah. He's going to be a fun interview, and we've got Will McIntyre tomorrow.
Tomorrow,
at 9
Will.
O'clock. Yeah.
Will's a Saline County boy.
Yeah, Brian Kidd.
His mom taught Meredith. What was it, Meredith? What grade? So that was fun having them. And
great
it was pops, the last time.
Great dad.
Absolutely. Yeah. And he's doing something with Car Time for every strike.
Will is. Oh, that's cool.
Will is, yeah. So he's doing something with them every strike or strikeout. I think it's strike, but we'll talk more about that tomorrow. But also enjoyed having Caleb Battle on one last time.
Yeah,
for the
sure
season.
Was. Yeah, it's been it'll be interesting to see when he makes his decision, how long it takes. Because I remember when Devo was going through that, he went through the NBA, I'm sure, the evaluation process. It took a while. Josh, you know the timeline on that, on the NBA evaluation?
It usually takes.
I can't remember when what the actual timeline is.
Well, go to the draft combine.
Yeah, so you're talking a month or two,
yep.
Right?
Yeah. You know, the one thing about him yesterday with Caleb is that in fact he did not hedge on anything.
Yeah.
He said, "Look, here's what I want to do.
Yeah.
I want to see where I stand in the NBA."
That's
and
right.
I'm paraphrasing. I'm going to see where I stand in the NBA draft. I want to know what's going on there, and if that's something that I like and want to pursue, yada yada. If not, then I will decide on what I'm going to do college-wise, whether I stay here or move on to effect, is what he said. And you can't ask for anything more than that to come from a guy.
Yeah, he's been straightforward the whole time. Very impressive. But yeah, Will McIntyre starts tomorrow, so we're looking forward to having that. Also, have a looks like we have a sponsor for Bo Mattingly. We'll announce that here on Friday. So excited about that. We'll be at either the VFW in Dardanelle
or Front Street Grill.
Or, it's raising money for that organization. You
we've got a call.
Melinda Mayo helped us. You know, help the VFW. I think it was 99.
I don't know the number.
I think it was 99
yes.
here in Little Rock, and so those organizations are
right off of Canis. Is that what it was? Big
always,
helicopter.
Always
there.
Looking for help. Yeah.
Looking forward to doing that. So we'll be up there Friday morning helping them
Big
out.
Big turnaround after Oakland Thursday night.
It will be. It will be. Jamie
That's
has offered
did,
up
though.
John's. That was a cool thing that you sent last night. Daly and Jocko were in Ohio?
Yeah, so it's funny. I saw on Instagram, you know, we had Jocko Dill the other day on the show, and he can perform in front of anybody.
Yeah.
But it was Daly and Jocko on stage, and I thought it was at Newport Beach because that's where they're at.
I would have thought so, too.
So I don't know how long ago it was, but it was in Ohio, and they're getting up there and entertaining. They're singing Sweet Home Alabama. They were singing the Alabama song that, Josh, what is the Alabama song that
sung where y'all mouth off?
At the Bama games where they have the
Dixieland Delight.
But anyway, Daly loves getting up there and singing, Jocko was great. But that was an Ohio crowd.
I don't know when that tradition started about Dixieland Delight. What's so good? Josh, sing along with it and tell me. Give me the words.
Do you know the alternative lyrics?
I can't say them.
You said them at the karaoke.
I did karaoke, but
there's one you can't say, right? Are they all that bad?
It's F Auburn.
Every one of them.
You have Tennessee too.
All of them.
And Tennessee too. Yeah.
Well, I didn't hear that in that song.
I didn't know every one of them were that.
And Tennessee too is the last one. So
So that's all they're doing. They're just an F every school.
There's a middle part.
Gotcha.
Spend my dollar.
Josh, can you do it?
Josh is struggling.
I don't stretch your voice.
Struggling.
All right, I'll stop it.
Roger, I wanted to bring this up because it is spring break. Did you see the story? And maybe Josh has heard about this. The big thing now that spring breakers are paying good money for, young men especially. Have you heard about it?
Wait a minute. I did see something. Go ahead. I'm trying to see.
A bartender in Florida is making bukus of money slapping spring breakers in the face.
Nope, didn't see it then.
It's called a hurricane shot. And but for $30, she puts like a shot, a long glass, and a shot of alcohol.
Yeah.
And then she will lean over and dump it into the mouth of the man who is on his knees, I think, or a little bit lower than her.
Okay.
After that, she has a pitcher of water. She throws it in the face of said young man that she just fed the shot to.
Yeah.
Then she slaps him in the face.
A wet face slap. That's a stinger.
And $30, and the men are loving it. So there you go. Yeah. You know,
how much if she slaps you on the bottom?
I don't know, but you can't roll reverse. Can't roll reverse. It's got to be
a woman
doing that to a man.
You know, I guess I've never.
You're not into the slapping?
Well, I'm not into paying somebody to slap me.
But
at a bar,
I know guys. Displeased situation.
I know guys that would, you know, maybe they had to get much action.
I bet you do,
maybe
Jerry.
That's all the action they've gotten is a slap, and they let's slap me. And
no, that's okay. But I'm not going to a bar.
I know $30. You know what? Spring break.
I'll kick you in the nuts for $10.
It's spring break. You do crazy things on spring break. But I'm gonna tell you.
Here's
what's crazy. How did this girl come up with that whole thing? How did she come up with that idea to go? You know what?
Yeah, who was it?
I'm gonna feed a shot to a guy. I'm gonna throw water in his face and then slap him. Yeah. You know what? He's gonna pay me $30.
And where did that money come from? What's the $30 all about? That's $30 for the drink.
Well, it's probably $10 for the drink.
Listen, you go to Saigon, it probably costs you a little bit more.
Anyway, I just
unreal.
That,
yeah. I don't understand. I've never been one to do. Well, I never had the kind of disposable income, and to do all that, and then you start drinking. And doing all that to kids. You sent me some other videos where there were some people daring somebody to do something, and a guy jumps off of a cruise ship.
I
dare you.
Oh, there's a man. Go have a seat there.
Gregory.
Let's go ahead. You got his open ready to rock and roll?
I'll get it right there. Yeah.
Craig, good morning. How are you?
Sorry I'm late.
Late. I didn't know you were late.
Yeah, it's okay.
I take my wife coffee every morning, and She throws it.
She's what now?
She throws it in my face and slaps me. And it's a tradition we've been carrying on since 1971.
What are the kids? What are the kids doing today? What is going? You pay a girl $30 to pour water in your face and slap you. But again, that is physical activity.
He's a legend in the state of Arkansas.
See, if y'all run out of the field, it's going to say, Texas.
His 55 years in television and radio broadcasting is unparalleled.
His name is Craig O'Neill.
He has helped raise over $9 million for charity. Brought to you by Petty Jean Meats. Petty Jean Meats, locally owned and operated for four generations. With Petty Jean Meats, people always know where their meat is coming from. Made right here in Arkansas. Please welcome Craig O'Neill.
Yeah! When we decided to do this agreement, I did not ask you, Craig, are you a morning guy? You know, you did that for 25 years, and then you shifted off that to do late night television. Is it tough for you coming out and joining us at 7?
No, I'm a morning person. Even when I was on TV, I'd still get up at 6 o'clock ready to come down here and do this show. I have yet to set an alarm that goes off and then wakes me up to come down here and do the show, because I'm up for 24 years on Channel 11. Absolutely. I'm getting up at 6 o'clock going, "Good morning, Little Rock!"
It's still there.
It's amazing that you were on there.
Several things to get to. Obviously, March Madness. Are you into the brackets and all the things?
Kansas all the way, baby.
Okay.
Kansas, feeling it from last year, being upset by Arkansas, overcompensates this year, gets on fire, and wins it all.
Josh,
Craig, I'm not sure if you saw yesterday, one of their best players is out for the tournament.
Well, there goes that one. The bracket falls in.
You want to go to plan B?
Sell me on somebody else, Craig. I was very compelled.
No, wait a minute. Hold on. I'm going to back off that. Because they overcompensate, because the players are, how many times have we seen a key player get hurt?
You're staying with Kansas.
And a team gets together, draws together, and wins it all.
They use it.
I think
the Razorbacks did that with Roger Crawford.
Exactly.
Yes.
And I'm going to have a perfect bracket. I'm going to win the $1 million for Oakland. And it's now going to be the Craig O'Neill Studio. Nice. I'm going to buy Frank Fletcher off.
By the way, go to the 103.7 The Buzz website to see the bracket challenge and all the details there.
Oh, yeah.
I do that. Several things. Oh, of course, you know, by the way, too, basketball is over for us in this state, but baseball, number one team in the nation.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah, all the polls. And we had Peyton Stovall start yesterday, and we got Will McIntyre Thursday. It's fun to follow. I mean, you got number one team in America right there.
Oh, my gosh. And Missouri got shut out 2 days in a row and lucky to have a run.
I know.
Isn't that wonderful?
Too bad, Josh.
We needed this,
absolutely,
folks.
Absolutely. It is.
Say hallelujah.
Major League Baseball has started, Craig, but it's in South Korea. Is that they're still playing spring ball, but the official first game of Major League Baseball is, I know, makes no sense.
What do you think?
Would you like to visit with the marketing director for who made that decision, thought that was a good idea?
Well.
And Josh, you made the point, the Dodgers who are playing in South Korea this first game come back to Florida and go back to a spring practice game, right? Right, Josh?
Yeah, I'm not sure they're going to Florida. They play the late spring training stuff in their own stadium sometimes.
And so they will play another exhibition game, even though
they've got three more exhibition games coming. And I think the Padres do as – yep, the Padres have two on Monday and Tuesday next week.
So, I just now noticed you all have it on. So this Los Angeles Dodgers-San Diego Padre game counts –
yes, cash towards the standing.
And they've got one more tomorrow.
Makes no sense.
Now, if one of these teams gets out of the playoffs by one game because they lost a game in Korea, they're going to look back on this and go, it was that dang Korean game.
I think the winner of that whole thing is a marketing person that says, you know, I'd like to take a trip to Korea.
Korea, let's go to Korea.
Why don't we do baseball?
And I was referencing, somebody pointed out that basketball is still going on. UCLA women still have a chance to play in their tournament. Same thing with Little Rock men and ASU men are playing in the, I never can get the name of the letters right, Josh, CBI, NIT, LRV, what is
CSI.
It? CSI. Yeah. What is the tournament name? CO?
I think it's CBI, isn't it?
Yeah. We said it yesterday. It's the tournament in Florida that's got 15 teams, right? Is it both? I think it's both Arkansas State and Little Rock's playing in that. Mm. I meant March Madness is done for Arkansas teams. But anyway, the
CBI.
Yes, that's it. Several things I want to get to today with you, Craig. Today is National Proposal Day. So I wanted to find out how you proposed to Jane. How many years ago? Where was that? What was the scoop?
It never was a proposal. It was an assumption.
Okay.
We just started assuming we were going to get married. I never got down on the knee. I never held up.
It just happened?
Held up the ring or the flowers. It was just an assumption. And it never was a formal proposal.
Does Jane ever go back and go, she sort of misses that you didn't get on your knee?
No, the guy
who does everything, who plans everything,
exactly,
says that you did not have a plan. I'm stunned.
Mr. Shtick, had no shtick.
Oh, my gosh.
I had a ring, but there was no formal proposal. It basically was this. We're at Bowen's in Jonesboro in 1970. So are we going to get married or what? We'll get married. Boom.
That was it.
Sorry, y'all.
Have you ever deep dive with her and go, honey, do you ever regret that?
Need to go to Petty Jean. Walk out on that rock.
Yes. Yes.
That's what you need to
Craig,
do.
You know what? We will help you.
Yeah. Here we go.
We'll do a show there.
We'll film.
Next anniversary is the 53rd. No, yeah, 53rd.
That's Basil's number. That's Basil's number.
I'll wear my jersey.
He wore that jersey.
He'll wear it.
I have married two people. I'd love to perform the ceremony. I've married two couples. Excuse me.
I've married 12. I'm legal, too.
Can you do yourself?
Well, true story, the one time I proposed, she said no.
What?
And then she said, just joking. Yeah, she did. How terrible is that? What? You know what, though? She was thinking, I'm going to go ahead and do this now because it ain't going to work. And so, that's right. So anyway, but Craig, at that moment, you're very vulnerable.
Very.
I mean, you put it out there.
Like the Sadie Hawkins dance, nah.
So listen, we will love to be a part of that. When you decide to do that, we'll be in the planning of it.
We're not letting you free. It's happening.
I'm not real sure I've decided to do that.
On that rock. It's up there on that. When is your anniversary? What month? What month?
August.
Would
you like to know why it's August 6th?
Because before football season.
High school football all-star game, and I had covered Jonesboro Hurricane, and I wanted to get married. And the next day, come down and watch Scott Bull in the Arkansas High School football game.
Oh, my gosh. No proposal, and your wedding is based on the all-star
you
want to
get married?
Exactly, David.
You want to get married?
The other thing is National Alien Abduction Day. Does Craig O'Neill believe in aliens?
Now's the time.
Well, I better, because everybody else in the household does.
Okay. And
so, yeah, I guess so. I kind of would like to see one or have a close encounters moment or see who gets off the spaceship, see if I know them.
All right, well, listen.
Chances are, if somebody's been abducted and they're coming off the spaceship, like in Close Encounters, they're going to walk up to me and go, hey, you did my prom.
Probably so. It's also, too, Won't You Be My Neighbor Day, Craig.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, the reason that's based, you know why?
Here you go, my new hero.
You know, human beings learn best and most from other human beings. That's all part of being human. And we learn best from people who really care about us. People we really like. It's you I like. It's not the things you wear. It's not
This country would be a lot better off if we had more
Fred Rogers.
Have you seen, obviously we're talking about Fred Rogers, Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. He died in February 2003, but today is his birthday. Have you seen the both the movie and the documentary on him?
Seen the documentary four times, seen the movie.
It is fascinating the kind of guy he was. And Roger, you know the story about the postman. I think that he washed his feet. On camera, and
a black postman.
Yeah. Thank you. And
got a lot of blowback because of that. But he is remarkable.
Had no idea what the man stood for and what he was doing. We just sort of, it's Mr. Rogers doing this little kid show, and so many angles, and he was doing things on purpose.
And now we look back on him and realized how revered he should have been.
Yeah,
and
even more.
My career, I started out idolizing Johnny Carson, but at the age of 73, I now idolize Mr. Rogers.
How about that?
And just playing that snippet.
Yeah.
That just and that's true.
Yeah.
And you'll find that the people the temperature who love you the world
down. You have a little bit of Mr. Rogers.
Right? Oh, I can go there.
I think you have a little bit of Mr. Rogers with your career.
He's clean.
Yeah.
Well, this is true. If you look at Craig and Tommy, if you look at the that's true.
180,
Craig,
180.
Yeah, you and Tommy were different kind of guys on that's the air, right. And
one's the angel and one's the devil on your shoulder. That's where we went. But here's the deal.
Because we also Roger and I went strong.
See, we dated a chick like Tommy, but we wanted to marry a chick like Craig.
That's right.
That's what we wanted.
But Roger and I were all
back off.
That's all a good.
Roger and I were also strong with the Captain Kangaroo back in the day.
Big fan like that,
Mr. Green. Well, I'm Green Jeans
and I'm
Bunny.
I made fun of Mr. Rogers in the early part of my DJ career. Everybody did. And but now he's just the things he said, what he did in his life, and it's reflected by that documentary, David.
So good. I had no idea. Josh, you're 27. Who did you growing up as a kid? Who did you have anybody like a Mr. Rogers that you watched that you learned
Barney?
From?
Was it Barney?
the dinosaur.
Teletubbies.
No. Nothing?
Not one.
Yeah.
Not like one. I mean, I guess.
Bill
Cosby. I mean, the Cosby Show was on a lot.
Well, you know, Cosby.
And Cosby did a
Little Bill was
what did
show.
He do? A little segment. Didn't he do a segment on Captain Kangaroo or something where he had a magic board or something as well?
Well, of course, got kids. Kids today now have access to 9,000 things on their phone.
Sure.
And, and so I don't know if somebody.
Instead of seeing Mr. Rogers and the neighborhood, you can see a guy get on his knees, pay a chick $30, drink a shot, and get slapped.
Yeah,
that's what you can see.
Did you want to make a comment on that? We're going to go from Mr. Rogers' neighborhood to what's happening in Florida with spring breakers.
Mr. Robinson's neighborhood.
Would you pay $30 to take a shot from a girl?
No, but I'd pay $30 to watch it.
I actually have watched it. I watched it, and the guy's loving it.
Oh, it's on YouTube, obviously.
It is everywhere. If a guy has not had much physical interaction with a female, that's probably the closest he's going to get. And and there's something to it when a woman slaps you and she's not really mad.
Is the bartender good looking?
I think so.
That's how Baz gets. There's something to it when a woman slaps you and she's not mad at you?
Yeah, listen, you would much rather have a woman slap you that's not mad at you than a woman who is.
Well,
yeah,
but as long as there might be makeup.
Yeah, that's exactly right. He hadn't gotten to that yet. Afterwards. He hadn't gotten to that yet. 661-1037. Yes, there you go. 661-1037 is the number. Craig O'Neill in studio today.
Yep, you got it. If it's Craig, it's Wednesday.
My gosh.
That's the point we want to get to.
I love that.
If I'm hearing Craig O'Neill on the buzz, it's Wednesday.
Boom. Oh, my gosh.
Got to make that connection.
Have you ever done the Tom Cruise across the floor in the underwear and socks? To this song.
Too old then. I'm way too old
now. I think you can still do it.
And we got how I proposed to my wife, actually.
We got
because I won a lip syncing contest for this song.
Wow, how about that?
In Hot Springs at Bobby's Socks or whatever it was, the bar across from the old J&S at Holiday Inn. I won a lip syncing contest. When I won, I took my pants off and slid. I won a dinner at that hotel, and it was at that dinner that I proposed to Samantha. How about
and
that?
When we come back to
40 years ago.
Wow.
When we come back, we've got to hear about that. I want to tell you a proposal about a potential prank that involves Roger that I think would really be hilarious. We'll talk about it when we come back. 7:30.
Presented by Gary Hill with MSS Oil, Splash Car Wash. There hasn't been an oil man specialist like this since Who Shot JR? Call Gary Hill with MSS Oil at 501-200-7089.
This is SportsCenter.
March Madness officially began last night with a pair of games at the First Four in Dayton. In the West region, it was 16 seed Wagner over 16 seed Howard, 71-68. Wagner will now take on North Carolina, who's the number one seed in the West. And then in the Midwest, it was Colorado State 67, UVA 42. The Rams will now take on number 7 seed Texas on Thursday. Two more games coming tonight in Dayton. First, it's Grambling in Montana State at 5:40 on True TV. Then at 8:10, it'll be 10 seed Colorado and number 10 seed Boise State. The first round will begin officially on Thursday. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Continuing to warm up across Arkansas, 75 today, mostly sunny. Could be a couple of showers or thunderstorms in North Arkansas. And tonight's low drops down to 50. Better rain chances statewide arriving for Thursday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Johnston's Home Center in Benton is your one-stop shop for appliances, bedding, lawn care, and sewing. That's right, Johnston's, your hometown shop for sewing and embroidery machines, supplies, fabrics, and more. For your outdoor needs, check out their steel chainsaws, leaf blowers, riding mowers, and a wide selection of lawn and garden equipment for the green thumb in your family. Johnston's Home Center, 1421 Military Road in Benton, or on the web at johnstonshomecenter.com. If they don't have it, you probably don't need it.
David Basil here for Jones & Son Diamond and Bridal Fine Jewelry. At Jones & Son, when you shop for an engagement ring, you get the benefit of shopping with the largest selection of rings in Central Arkansas. Jones & Son also carries the biggest brands in the business. At Jones & Son, shop their new collection of Jones & Son branded engagement rings. These Jones & Son rings are high quality at a fraction of the price. They're also fully customizable. They can modify any design to suit your needs. Jones & Son is located at 1121 Rodney Parham Road. And of course, they've been there for over 35 years. Same address, same phone number for over three decades. Finding the perfect piece of jewelry to match the occasion can be overwhelming, but it doesn't have to be, and it's not at Jones & Son Diamond and Bridal Fine Jewelry. Find the right diamonds for that special occasion. Jones & Son invites you to come by and shop with them in person or online at jonesandson.com. Owners Darrow and Jacob Jones are the best father-son jewelry team in America. Tell them the guys at Morning Mayhem sent you. Jones & Son Diamond and Bridal Fine Jewelry. Jones & Son is located at 1121 Rodney Parham Road.
Spring has sprung, and that spells fun. Fun is in Arts Marine in North Little Rock. Arts has new 2024 G3 Tritunes. That's right, I said Tritunes in stock. And as always, don't forget Arts Marine is your John Boat headquarters. They're powered by Tohatsu and Yamaha outboards. Arts also has an excellent selection of the ever so popular G3 boats, models 22, 23, and 2024. Make your summer one to remember by stopping by Arts Marine in North Little Rock. Take the Levy exit.
On March 30th, one lucky Saracen casino player will win a Corvette Stingray from Guatney Chevrolet. This new Corvette is the pinnacle of precision, and with 500 horses in 0 to 60 in under 3 seconds, you'll have more speed than you'll ever need. You can win the most powerful production Stingray in history just for playing, but only at Saracen Casino Resort. Start playing today.
Saracen Casino Resort, Vegas, Arkansas style.
Gambling problem? Call 800-522-4700.
This is Quinn Grovey, and you're listening to Morning Mayhem on 103.7 The Buzz.
Drum like timbals, whatever that means. So I don't know what that means, but it's...
Sounds cool.
I think I saw Baz's timbals in Aspen.
That's our man, Justin Moore. That was the timbals in Aspen. Justin's taking spring break with his family, which a lot of people are doing spring break. Go by the zoo, where we were yesterday.
Go by the zoo.
You had a good time.
I had a great time there.
Morning Mayhem is here for you today. We appreciate you tuning in. That's Roger Scott. I'm David Basil. Josh Neighbors producing. And Craig O'Neill with us.
Good morning, everyone.
Before I get to the bit, that's why. I can drink.
Wednesday.
We were talking. That's right. It's Wednesday. Bo Mattingly, who's going to be a regular on the show on Friday, used to. You know, I forget sometimes. You spent 8 years covering sports for THC.
Got to know him.
And that you said some of your favorite things were watching Bo go after Mike Irwin go
and
after
back,
each other
and vice versa. Yeah. Those two, ladies and gentlemen, if we could, in fact, if you all ever want to take a vacation, just get Bo and Mike Irwin on here and just have them talk.
Roger, Mike Irwin is the biggest curmudgeon and been around forever. He was up there previous to me.
Is that a toupee?
Yes, I think it looks like it is.
It looks like it anyway.
And I forget back then, you know, Bo was covering on a daily basis.
Oh, gosh, which, we'd all get together, and I would end up laughing as I listened to these two guys.
Yes.
Golly, they were great.
So you've got to hear the story, Craig. Roger brought this up yesterday, and I said, we have got to get Craig in the mix on this. So explain the situation.
I got a message from my friend Bill Lawrence, who told me about something that happened to Jamie Daly when Jamie Daly, John's brother, who was looking for me to tell us about our event coming up Friday morning. Well, Jamie called a wrong number. He had two numbers in his deal. One was my old number.
And I've had this new number, I don't know, let's say for sake of argument, a half a dozen years. But the guy that's got the old number hates me with a passion.
Really? No, really hates Roger.
He cusses out everybody. Great. Worse than you and Pass the Ammo. He cusses out everybody. My oldest son one time called that number because he didn't have my new number. Absolutely, because he had two in his phone. Called, and the guy sent me a message cussing me out, going, "Your own blankety blank son doesn't have your blankety blank number. You blankety blank. You're the worst.
Still doing
you're
that.
You're the worst. I know who you are. You're the worst person ever. This and that." And I told the guy, I said, "What can I do?
Change it."
I said, I can't.
But that's where you—that's where you come in.
And this is where you come in. Yeah. And I don't think the guy may be listening. I don't know if he's listening. Then the bitch ruined.
You need to call him and consult. You just need to change your number.
You've got to call in as someone who works for the cell phone company, and you insist on him changing his number because I need that number.
Back.
I need a second number now for all of my fans and friends.
Hey, listen, can that guy still mad? I remember Roger telling this story years ago, and then so Jamie calls, and he's still cussing people out.
And then tell him, as an aside, you know, here at the phone company, we don't charge him because he's such a big celebrity. Yeah. And so many people love him.
Whatever you think.
Oh. Somebody makes,
and if you give him a chance, you'll love him too.
Somebody's making a point here. Well, we could really mess his world up. You could give out your old number on the phone. I mean, on the air.
I won't do that.
We're not going to do that.
Not on the air, but I will send it to you.
I did want to share with you.
Where do I plug this in? I just now knocked out the. Let's see here. Ladies and gentlemen, I can't go anywhere now without any technical issues. Anywhere.
I hear Bill Cosby did do picture pages on Captain Kangaroo. So I remember watching Bill Cosby do that, picture pages on Captain Kangaroo. We were talking about, I know that when Josh mentioned Bill Cosby doing some things, I do remember him being on Captain Kangaroo. It was in the latter years.
So we try to learn something on the show every day because we're not the smartest. And
I've noticed.
One of the days, in addition to National Proposal Day and National Ravioli Day and National Alien Abduction Day, is National Bibliomania Day. And I was going to ask Craig, do you have any idea what bibliomania is?
I would assume it would be something to do with books.
That is it. I'm going to stop you there. Yes, go ahead.
So it would be a fascination with books? Or?
I'm going to give you credit, Roger. Wow. As a king of all trivia, we would give him the correction. I mean, we would give him the correct answer. Today commemorates the anniversary of the great grand heist of 23,600 books by Stephen Blumberg.
Wow.
So bibliophilia is the love of books. But bibliomania is the compulsive disorder of hoarding books.
Got it.
This obsession collecting books can even go on to damage a person's social relations or health.
See? So I've learned something. I don't know about y'all.
Stephen Blumberg was also known as the book bandit. He was from Iowa. He hoarded thousands of books. He amassed 23,000 plus from 327 libraries and museums across 45 states, two provinces in Canada, and the District of Columbia.
Wow.
The combined worth of the books was estimated to be $5.3 million. On March 20th, 1990, Blumberg was caught when his friend turned him over to the FBI.
Wow.
I had never heard of this before until I saw that yesterday.
I've got it. In 2014, Entertainment Weekly magazine published the 100 greatest novels ever written. Entertainment magazine.
Right.
So I go, you know what? I'm going to read
them. You're going to collect
them. So beginning in 2014, I started reading the 100 greatest novels on that list. I'm down to book 8.
You were kidding me.
I'm on John Updike's Rabbit Run Quartet. It's a 4-book series.
Wow.
But I'm in the second book. But the point being, not only that book, but other books.
You are a book lover.
Oh, my gosh. You ought to
see. You might could fit into this.
They are everywhere in my house.
Is Jane okay with that? Is she okay? Does she read
too? No.
Actually,
she's got books everywhere, too. We both.
Roger, I think books look cool in the house, but I don't have time to read them.
I mean,
they look good.
Oh, yeah.
Mahogany.
Mahogany, the Anchorman.
My wife orders. There's a new book from Amazon coming in every day. As a matter of fact, she's got two of the same books coming in that'll be here Friday that I'll need to take one of them back. She orders so many books, she's doubling up on.
So do you have books everywhere?
Everywhere.
Do you have the fascination of collecting, like this guy,
and
maybe?
Do and buying them. And to me, Barnes & Noble and Wordsworth, the two greatest stores in Central Arkansas.
And
now it's children's books.
Yeah.
because I go read to school.
That's the other part of it. You're big into books because you're reading books and you're writing a book.
And I'm writing one. And yeah, exactly. But I'm not going to buy it unless I'm going to read it.
Right.
If it comes into the house, I'm going to read it. And here's another thing. If I start a book, I'm going to finish it.
Well, that's
now, Jane, if she starts a book and doesn't like it, she'll toss it aside.
Okay.
I'm going, what are you doing?
You have the obligation. You feel that in the need to finish the book.
Mm-hmm. Even finish
it. How many books? How many books?
I'm with Jane. It's got to capture me right away or I'm out.
How many books have you think you've read in your life?
Oh, my
gosh.
In your life.
In your whole life. Starting at the very beginning.
500? 700?
Here's the thing. In 2000, I really began to read on a regular basis. Because up until 2000, because of the radio schedule, mm-hmm. you all know you can't read. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to schools for 20 years saying, read books. It helps your imagination muscle. And I'm coming back from Sheridan in the year 2000, and I'd scored. Everybody had laughed and blah, blah, blah,
uh-oh.
Blah, blah. Craig,
something hit you.
And I felt so good. Yeah. And a voice in my head says, you know, you're not reading. You tell the kids to read, but you're not reading. And I caught myself in the hypocritical minute.
You can't do it, can you?
You're too good.
Is that the voice
of God? No, that's the voice of Fred Rogers.
It was the
Fred Rogers.
Rogers' voice is the voice of, you know.
When you felt that, you go, okay, it's time to change.
So for 30 minutes a day, beginning in the year 2000, I read a book. And the first year, I felt so good. I read 22 books. The next year, I read 23. And then I go MC an Oak Grove High School day in which it's the 25-book day. They're challenging all the high school students to read 25 books because when you read 25 books, you're reading a million words and improving your vocabulary.
I went,
I've read that. And I went back and checked. No, I'd only read 22. So now it's 200 pages a week.
That's what it is.
So what does that come to?
200 pages a week.
It's about 42 books a year.
Oh yeah, but time-wise, you said 30 minutes a day is when you started.
Started
to give yourself a start.
In 2002, I began 200 pages a week. So I'm average 42 books a year.
So at 200 pages a week, how much time does it take?
Yeah, that's what I'm asking. Time-wise,
200 pages a week is still 30 minutes a day. But on weekends, you have an hour.
Josh, do you? So Josh is 27.
Josh, do you read
hardcover books? Do you have time? Do you read much?
Are they all mad?
And if you do you read digital or do you read hardcover?
If I read. Actually, it's a combination of both.
Okay, because to me, Craig, too. I do it because I can be somewhere I can take my computer out and read digital, but I'd rather have the book in my
hand. Exactly, because that's the world.
The physical world.
Yeah.
That's the world. When you have the book, that's the whole world. When you have it on digital, you close the lid and you go, what else is on there? I got to go look at some other stuff. I got to look up ESPN or maybe Oklahoma.
And if you're at the airport, if you have your book with you, you have the book, you can open it up. That's physical. You can look at it.
Don't need a connection. Don't need a connection.
Uh-uh.
Which sometimes when you get in the plane, planes don't have it. Yeah, no. I think that, you know, same thing with the newspaper. I think there's something to having something that you handle.
Yes.
Well, that's fascinating. I wondered. I knew because you were reading. You had that. It was almost like Paul having the vision, and that you were driving. You were leaving Sheridan.
That's at some point. In fact, I think that's one of my chapters in the book.
You should. How many kids? How many times have you read to kids? How many have you? Have
oh
you kept
my
it with that?
Gosh, dog.
I'm sure it would be thousands. It would be at least a couple thousands. Yeah. Is there one book that you go to for all your kids' stuff?
There is a book called Rosie's Time to Shine, which is about a child that is jealous of another child, but in the end, they become best friends because the child at the end of the book steps up and helps out with the girl she's
so that and you read that. That's your sort of go-to.
That's kind of become my go-to, but.
What is the, you know, you and I do a lot of stuff where we're out in front of the public and speaking. Which is your target age for the kids? Because that's what you're...
Second grade.
So it's just the second grade.
Because if we don't have them reading on grade school level, on their level, by third grade, that's either a dropout or a prison bed or both.
Wow, very nice. That's well said. Now, do you, when you go in, if somebody hears you right now, and we want to ask Craig to come speak, do you read for 30 minutes, an hour? I know what my limit is when I speak. I lose an audience after a certain amount of time. What is your time? The perfect time.
It averages, I'm sure, around 35 minutes. But now there's 20 minutes of shtick.
Sure, that's
or
okay.
25 minutes, and then there's 10 minutes of the book, and then there's the after.
Yes.
The questions and the things brought up in the book, and the things that you came from the book.
Do you show the pages?
show the try read, to. Yeah. Now, if you have a large crowd, you can't show the pages.
Correct.
But you try to. Now, here's the here's what I love. LeVar Burton came to town.
Right.
And he's big into reading because he had the Reading Rainbow. Exactly. Right. So we go to a school over at Washington Elementary, and we see the science of reading taught by a first-grade teacher, and she is showing how letters have sounds, letters together have sounds. These sounds produce words that produce images that become sentences, and every one of those children is bought in.
How about that?
And they're leaning forward, and that's when you know you got them.
Yeah,
when they're leaning forward, yeah. And they're getting it. And suddenly it came upon me where all this fits in. Dolly Parton Imagination Library brings books into the home and kids get used to having them. And then the science of reading teaches the basics and fundamentals. And then in second and third grade, Craig O'Neill shows up and shows fun with books. That's my role. Once that has been set, I come in and say, this is a glorious moment when you open that book and the adventure begins, which, by the way, is the summer theme at libraries across Arkansas. The adventure begins, and every book, my friends, is an adventure.
Hogalooga. Roger, Roger.
Say hello.
Hogalooga.
Roger, if people should go back to our stream if they're in their car and they can't watch this and watch the passion of Craig O'Neill as he explains this. How do you again, Craig?
73.
So here's the deal. He's at age 73, and he's decided he's done all these amazing things, but you still want to make a difference, and you're passionate about it. How about it? Just goes to show you, no matter how old you are, you can still impact people's lives, especially kids. I mean, it's not easy to be 73 and impact kids, and you're doing it. We love you
for
that.
And today, Craig, I have a meeting.
I get chills.
Hoping to get a sponsor for the reading tour that can pick up the Reading Road Tour, and we'll let you know, because I've kind of said, hey, if they sponsor me, we'll mention them every once in a while.
Yeah, yeah. How can folks find you if they want to sponsor you? You want to throw out how much it is? Is there a
figure? Well, no, we're going to get into that. We're not going to wait into it's well into the 100.
How can they find you, though? We asked you this last time. You go, I got to work on Facebook. They reach out to Facebook.
Oh, yeah, Facebook, at Craig O'Neill TV.
Okay, I'm thinking somebody
may give them a phone number.
Oh, that's right.
I got one. What's yours? What's your old one?
All right, we'll come back and wrap things up with Craig. 7:45.
Joe Klein, got a couple of questions for you. Did you know that Corky's Barbecue has two great locations here in Central Arkansas?
Yes, Roger, I knew that. I've been telling you that for years.
But did you know they have drive-thrus at both locations so I don't have to get out of my car?
Yes, Roger.
But did you know this, that Corky's Barbecue can cater a wedding or office party?
Have you ever seen anything we do for the Buzz, the golf tournaments, countdown to kickoff? Yes, Corky's caters and does bulk orders. Who do you think brings all that barbecue, slaw, baked beans, and all the fixings to these events?
Fair enough. But Joe, I bet you didn't know this, that Corky's has private rooms available.
I don't even know why I talk to you.
It's because we're best friends. Now, all this talk about Corky's Barbecue is making me hungry. How about we run on over to one of them, grab some ribs?
Really? But you don't even pay.
Hey, that reminds me. I need a couple of gift cards.
Whatever. We're done here.
Let Corky's do all the work. For groups of 10 or more, whether it's for your cherished family gathering or your office party, this year, let the experts handle it.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock are opening March 27th. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor, appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more at the all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock.
Hey, it's Craig O'Neill, and I want to share with you a conversation I had recently with the parent of a teenage son. It seems on Saturdays, this young kid sleeps late, unless they fix Petit Jean bacon at breakfast. And that flavor is all-powerful and wakes that kid up. He comes right into the kitchen. And why shouldn't that flavor be powerful? They smoke it for 16 hours. That's why you get the hickory flavor. And not just the bacon, but the bologna, the Polish sausage, the hot links, whatever you pick out. That's Petit Jean. Oh, you'll taste the difference.
Hello, Buzz listeners. This is Chris Zender with Fletcher Dodge, and I want to help you lower your car payment. Let us show you how you can trade in your old car for a brand new Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, or Ram with a lower car payment. We've got 0% financing on new Rams, or you can take up to $12,000 off the sticker. It's your choice. We also have 0% financing on new Chrysler Pacificas and $10,000 plus discounts on new Jeep Gladiators. Or how about a new Dodge Charger or Challenger for $5,000 off? We've got lots of inventory to choose from. Just pick one out and tell us how much you want to pay. We'll do the rest. Don't worry about your credit. If other dealers have told you no, come see us and let us help you get a new or pre-owned dependable vehicle. Go to FletcherDeals.com and simply click Apply for Financing and we'll do the rest. At Fletcher Dodge, you always get the best price, the lowest finance rate, and more for your trade. And also a hassle-free buying experience. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood or shop online at FletcherDeals.com.
Is your Oaklawn Thoroughbred racing action so close you can feel it? Or is it the view from your trackside luxury suite? However you like it, racing season is off and running at Oaklawn, with live races every weekend through May 4th. It's fun by the furlong all season long. Make your reservations today at oaklawn.com. What's your Oaklawn? Gambling problem? Call 1-800-522-4700.
Red tape. One in three businesses will get caught up in it, and they'll be penalized by the IRS for mismanaging their payroll. Because when you're handling payroll, HR compliance, and those constantly changing tax laws, that red tape can get sticky in a hurry. At The Payroll Company, we free you from that tangled mess and get you back to business. The Payroll Company. Less headaches, more than payroll. Visit morethanpayroll.com to learn more.
Roger Scott here. Let me remind you about my friends at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union. They have some of the most aggressive auto loan rates for Buzz listeners in Saline, Grant, Garland, Hot Spring, and Perry counties. Easy access to Alcoa's team of loan officers online, by phone or in person, at Alcoa Community Federal Credit Union's two locations in Benton and Sheridan, and apply online at alcoacommunityfcu.org.
Did Josh miss another curse word in a movie clip? Let us know at 501-661-1037. Welcome back to Morning Mayhem, live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios. Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Older women are beautiful lovers.
All right, 7:51 here on Morning Mayhem. Craig O'Neill brought to you by Petty Jean Meats in studio. We're going to try to get a clip of what Craig just shared with us, the passion he has, his plan, the revelation that he had.
Don't get me started.
The revelation leaving Sheridan. The road from Sheridan.
They're doing a new they've got the new Roadhouse out. And yes, they got other people playing. If they do a remake of Pass the Ammo, you're the preacher now. You're the preacher.
That's right.
You're in the movie.
I learned a little bit about bibliomania with Craig today. Also wanted to ask you, do you know on this day, Craig, 1969, John Lennon did what that changed the future of the Beatles? 1969, what did he do on this day? Much to the chagrin of most Beatle fans.
Oh.
He said we're bigger than Jesus.
No, it's worse.
Much
worse.
Did he say I do?
Much worse.
Did he say I do?
He said he got married to Yoko Ono. That basically destroyed the Beatles
that
after that. Yes,
yeah,
that's exactly right.
Yoko.
Yeah, also,
what are you doing, John?
On this day, Roger played it earlier, 1948, 76 years ago, Craig, Zippity Doo-Dah.
Oh, we love it.
From Song of the South, won Best Original Song at the 20th Academy Awards. You know, you hear those songs Roger was talking about, how good they are, how well written they are, and how fun they are.
It just makes you feel happy.
Yeah, I'm sure you didn't play that on B98, but just when you hear it, it does make you happy. And then the.
It happened on one of them zippity-doo-dah days. Now, that's the kind of day when you can't open your mouth.
Come on, Craig.
Without a song, jump right out of it. Zippity-doo-dah, zippity-ay. My, oh, my, what a wonderful day.
Come on, Honky.
Plenty of sunshine hitting my way.
Come on.
Zippity-doo-dah, zippity. We need a little bit more of that.
Mr. Blue.
The other thing I noticed, Roger, on this day,
yes,
Craig, do you remember the movie Basic Instinct?
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yes, it's one of the most horrifying movies. RJ Hawk joins us now.
I guess.
Yeah,
hi, Hawky.
If you're a dude, you're a guy, and you're terrified by this, because I said yesterday that I actually experienced a little bit of that, and, I didn't know if you when you dated Jay, you didn't have much.
No, you're thinking Fatal Attraction.
Yeah.
That was your
there's maybe a little bit of crossover in Basic Instinct too. Just saying.
Michael Douglas in both of them?
You're right.
Is that right?
You are right, Roger.
Give me
a Corky's gift certificate for my troubles.
Of course, you know the thing about Basic Instinct was the famous scene with the Sharon Stone, right?
What was the scene, David?
Very revealing.
Well, we talked about two different reveals with Craig O'Neill today. Yeah. Sharon Stone and on the way from Sheridan. Two distinctly different things.
Sharon and Sheridan.
Very good. I did want to ask you too. Jerry Reese's birthday today. We love Jerry Reese. Smokey and the Bandit. When you're hot, you're hot.
Oh yeah.
When you're not, you're not. Mm-hmm. And She's Got the Gold Mine, I Got the Shaft. And Amos Moses. I didn't know if.
Oh yeah, I remember that song. Yeah.
That's,
is he still alive?
He died in 2008. But he's alive in our hearts.
Darn right.
Amos Moses was a Cajun. He lived by himself in the swamp. He hunted alligator for a living. He just knock him in the head with a stump. The Louisiana law gonna get you, Amos. It ain't legal hunting alligator down in the swamp, boy. Now everybody blamed his old man.
What does Craig O'Neill have in? You know, it's just spring. Today is the first full day of spring. What does that mean to Craig O'Neill? Does that mean that you get out and walk a little bit more, that you and Jane will take advantage
of
the springs, the creeks of Arkansas and the rivers? And
I'm
those
looking things. Forward to the first day of spring can only mean Arkansas Derby.
Okay, yeah, and you pointed out.
Man, you have brought up that track.
Listen, you love horses. You talked about Frank Fletcher's horse, Rocket Can. Yes.
Big win on Saturday.
I'm surprised they have not locked you into you doing something over there just around the horses, maybe you being a stall helper. You know,
a stall helper.
Let me confess something, since you all are bringing it out of me today.
Yes,
all
right, yes. Sir.
I don't want to work in Oaklawn. I just want to go love Oaklawn.
Okay.
That's it. I don't want to have to go down there and do anything. Yep. I just want to go down there and love on the horse.
Could you talk? Do you think you can communicate with the horses?
Yeah. This is so weird. When I was in radio, RJ, we took a pet psychic to the track.
Yes.
And we had the list of the horses in the first race that day. It was in the morning. And she went and bonded with them and read them, and she had her crystals with her, and we went to every horse stall,
right.
And she would turn to us after each horse give us her take.
Wow.
And by the end of that, there was a small contingent of track workers, assistant trainers, and trainers following us around to see what she was going to say about their horse. Now, she did nail a couple of horses. There's one she went up to, and I'll never forget. She goes, "This horse has been ill, and it's coming back, and it's not real sure it wants to run." And she didn't know anything. There was nothing in advance. We told her about it, and that's when she got the crowd of people around her that followed her.
Do you you feel comfortable around a horse? You know, petting a horse and all the things.
Did you get bit one time?
I got bit. Yeah. The horse saw the fear in my eye, went to my clavicle, bit me. When they see your lips, I'm sure they feel very comfortable. They love the lips. They love the lips.
Right. If there are several horses I've been on, if it had my lips, it would have won by a lip.
Do you have much time? Do you get over there to Oaklawn?
Not enough.
Okay. Listen, we've talked about going to Fayetteville. We need to do that.
I gotta go.
Spring practice for baseball. You need more trips. Listen, Roger and I are over there quite a bit. They're a great partner with us.
We get rooms. You can share one of them.
Well, here's the thing. If this is going to be the Oaklawn studio,
can you
all be able to wager in here?
Yeah, we can.
Oaklawn anywhere.
We have covered so much great things. The most exciting, maybe, is that next year we're going to be a part of when Craig proposes to Jane.
I heard
after
about
all
that
these
on the
years.
53, number
53. Yes, 53 years that the proposal finally comes.
I can't wait.
Oh, I'm going to get home today and hear. This is what I'm going to hear when
I'm
going to
give you away.
No, I'm
going to give you away.
What are you going to hear?
When I get home today, I'm going to get hands on the hip going, whatever.
Whatever.
Man.
All right. Well, hey, if it's Wednesday at the Buzz, it's Craig. Thank you, Craig. Thanks to Petty G Meat. Have a great one. See you. Love you, too. See you next week, buddy. 8 o'clock. Stop me now. Have a good time. Stop me now.
is David Basil for Edwards Food Giant. On Morning Mayhem, we love talking about family-owned businesses here in Arkansas, and that includes Edwards Food Giant, the meat people. For the past 60 years, the Edwards family has been taking care of Arkansans with grocery stores across the state, and even after six decades, they are continuing to grow. But if you ask my mother, Mama Baz, it's not the number of stores in the Edwards Food Giant chain or their amazing meat and deli departments. For her, it's simple, customer service. It's now become one of her favorite places to shop just because of the way she's treated. Of course, the prices are always outstanding at Edwards, and the stores are always immaculate. Then you throw in new additions like curbside pickup and their great website, edwardsfoodgiant.com. It all adds up to make the Edwards experience easy and rewarding. Speaking of rewards, you can also shop, earn, and save with the Edwards Reward Program. Ask about it the next time you visit or read about it online at edwardsfoodgiant.com. And just like a great Arkansas family-owned business, Edwards also loves to give back to their community. Find the Edwards Food Giant nearest you today.
You can hear the best of the NCAA tournament on 106.7 Buzz 2 from the very beginning all the way to the championship game. March Madness on 103.7 The Buzz and 106.7 Buzz 2.
ESPN and The Buzz gives you the complete sports and entertainment package.
I love that game.
103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock. Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
The executive director of the Clinton National Airport was involved in a shootout with federal agents Tuesday morning. ATF agents were performing a search warrant at 53-year-old Brian Malinowski's home in West Little Rock Tuesday morning. While serving the warrant, ATF officials say Malinowski opened fire, injuring one person. Agents fired back and injured the executive director of the airport. He and the agent were sent to the hospital for treatment. The agent had non-life-threatening injuries, while Malinowski's injuries are unknown. Many people might be concerned about their cell service when the solar eclipse happens April 8th. Cell service reps don't anticipate many issues when the eclipse happens, but there are some things to be on the lookout for. Since many are coming to Arkansas, one rep says to make sure you have the latest software downloaded on your device. And another from AT&T says when it's packed, you can move back and forth to LTE and 5G network to find internet. The networks will be monitoring the event closely. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
Anywhere in the state, dial 888-888-8888 for Rainwater Holton Sexton. They'll help you weather the storm.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Continuing to warm up across Arkansas, 75 today, mostly sunny. Could be a couple of showers or thunderstorms in North Arkansas, and tonight's low drops down to 50. Better rain chances statewide arriving for Thursday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Tune in each week to Out of Bounds to hear from team captain Kendall Diggs. Omaha is the goal, and we're looking for a great season. Kendall Diggs is brought to you by Stephen Elmore with Shelter Insurance. For auto, home, life, or business insurance, see shelter agent Stephen Elmore or give him a call at 501-537-0959.
Hey folks, it's David Basil out here at Fletcher Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sherwood. Fletcher Dodge wants to help you lower your car payment. Come on in and let them show you how. It's possible to trade in your old car for a brand new Dodge Chrysler Jeep or Ram with a lower car payment. They've got 0% financing on new Rams, or you can take up to $12,000 off the sticker. Your choice. And how about 0% financing on new Chrysler Pacificas and $10,000 discounts on new Jeep Gladiators? Or how about a new Dodge Charger or Challenger for $5,000 off. Fletcher Dodge has lots of inventory to choose from. They'll do the rest. And don't worry about your credit. If other dealers have told you no, come see us and let us help you get a new vehicle to get you to school or to work. For the best selection, lowest price, and best buying experience, go see my friends at Fletcher Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sherwood, or you can shop online at FletcherDeals.com. Remember, 0% financing on new Rams, or you can take up to $12,000 off the sticker. That's just one of many deals they'll give you over at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Connor has cash. Once again, Connor has cash at the Pickles Gap Weapon Shack in Conway. Connor will buy your used weapon, or he will buy your entire collection. Once again, Connor has cash, and he wants to buy your used weapons at the Pickles Gap Weapon Shack, Highway 65 North in Conway.
Hi, I'm David Dunn with Central Arkansas Truck and Trailer, Arkansas's most trusted, highly rated, locally owned, and family-operated heavy and medium-duty diesel repair service. From Fords to Freightliners, specializing in suspensions, transmissions, brakes, DPF systems, and complete engine rebuilds. Tired of paying high dealership prices with long wait times? Let Central Arkansas Truck and Trailer get your truck back on the road where it belongs. Take Exit 7 off of I-440. That's Central Arkansas Truck and Trailer.
The most common form of treatment for the arthritic joints is normally cortisone injections and gel shots and over-the-counter medications. And most patients have tried all of that and are still in pain.
Every day, Dr. Aaron Wolkoff, a QC Kinetics medical director, meets patients who have exhausted every method to get relief. They've been told surgery is their only option.
They want to stay away from that path, and they come to us almost as a last hope. So we're using our own body's properties to help manage pain, to help slow arthritis down, keep the patients active with no downtime, and get them back to what they enjoy doing. I mean, I love what I do.
QC Kinetics regenerative treatments from our board-certified providers help heal and restore aching joints. No surgery, harmful drugs, or downtime. Call for your free consultation today.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
For those who push the boundaries and know no barriers, the wake up at nooners and dessert before dinner eaters, the jackpot dancers and sequined pantsers, the risk takers and heartbreakers, the hapless, the rogue, and the hopeless romantics, our time has come. Play bold at the new Southland Casino Hotel, the Mid-South's premier gaming destination. Plan your stay at southlandcasino.com.
Hey, Howie, what is going on at the Robert Irwin Jewelers in the McCain Mall in North Little Rock this Saturday?
The 6-hour 60% off sale.
60% off? You mean up to 60% off?
No, let me clear this up. It's not up to. It is 60% off. Between the hours of 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. this Saturday, you could get 60% off anything that's in our showcases.
This Saturday only at the Robert Irwin Jewelers located in the McCain Mall in North Little Rock.
It's a legit 60% off sale. Do not miss it.
Rock and roll sushi. Deliciously twisted flavors and a rock and roll vibe that'll blow your mind. Try a made-from-scratch hibachi menu. Chicken, shrimp, filet, or lobster with grilled vegetables and fried rice. Rockandrollsushi.com.
Now with 5 locations in Central Arkansas.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem.
Defense on me!
Live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios.
I don't want them to gain another yard.
Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
You blitz all night!
Here is David Basil, Roger Scott, and Justin Moore.
Leave no doubt!
A man of many talents, play-by-play broadcaster, real estate agent, and now state legislator. It's time to talk all things Arkansas with R.J. Hawk, presented by Natural State Wholesale, proudly trusted by major manufacturers all over the world for 25 years. Go see the flooring king, Don Gresham, at Natural State Wholesale.
Good morning. Slam-a-ram-a-woo!
There he is. The one only R.J. Hawk. Good morning, R.J. How are you?
You know, Craig talks about when you hear Craig, it means it's Wednesday. Not so much for R.J. He said, when you hear R.J., it just means it's another day, Monday through Friday.
You have been on every day.
I love the flexibility.
You know, there was a time
that when we started this gig, it was like, okay, we're going to get you up every Wednesday.
Was that the day?
That was the day. And so we got kind of used to that. In fact, Roger was sending me texts going, hey, looking forward to see you tomorrow. Nope. It'll be Thursday this week.
Then I think the time shift happened when Tommy came on.
And then, well, and I didn't even know I got bumped then. And I saw a Facebook thing that said, Tommy Smith going to be on at 8 o'clock.
As you know, all things can change. Yeah.
Brother,
so,
thank you. Thank you for doing it.
Your flexibility is so good.
I love it. I'm just glad that you guys allow me to come do this. Thanks to Natural State Wholesale in Cabot. Went up there and saw the warehouse the other day.
Yeah, I got to get up there. Wow. I saw Drew and Don at the concert, Tyler Kent's concert Saturday night. So, so obviously you're a big baseball fan,
yeah.
RJ.
Yeah.
And you were looking up at the game and
ridiculous.
It's just we've talked about this when you were
because they're gonna go back and play spring training games.
I know.
And look, Rob Manfred can't. He's. I think he's retiring at the end of this season. I believe it is. So, good riddance. This should not be happening
right now. Are the Rangers expected? Are they a favorite? If we looked at the Oakland Sports app, Josh, to see if
we are not the favorite to win the World Series.
Josh looked that up.
I think we're number two or three.
Who's that? Dodgers? Are they the favorite?
Dodgers are favored to win the World Series, and then I think the Astros, because they're about to
same
get Blake.
Players. Yeah,
they're about to get Blake Snell, I think, and so those two. But hey, we're the world champs. Can't take it away until October. So
did you see the story, RJ? And this is where you're wearing multiple hats here.
Dodgers,
did you see the story?
Astros, Yankees.
Say that again.
Oh, they changed a little bit.
Dodgers, Braves, Astros, Yankees.
Gotcha.
Well, you know you're not in the top four, RJ.
It must have changed since the last time I looked at it. Yeah.
Well, they got to be close to that, right? Are the Rangers close to that top four? Or no,
they are sixth.
Okay.
Six. We got bumped a
lot. Doesn't matter where you start.
It doesn't matter where you finish. It's where you finish. You know what? We weren't picked to win the World Series last year. You know what? Who's the world champs now?
That's right. Crazy story we mentioned earlier. The head of the Little Rock Airport.
Yes.
Who makes $264,000 a year, mm-hmm. was raided by, in his West Little Rock home, by ATF agents.
Saw that.
Apparently, he was collecting the guns that were collected
at the airport.
And selling them on the black market.
Okay, here's the thing.
And the pocket knives.
Can you tell me?
Wow. So he's got my pocket knife that I did this thing. So, like, I carry a pocket knife, just like Justin, and apparently you do as well.
Yeah.
And I just forgot to take it out. It's just one of those things. Yes. So I get to TSA, and they were like, I knew it. I could pull it out. Oh, no.
But you could have taken it back to your car.
I could have, but the line was really
long.
Can
you do that with a weapon, a gun?
No. I think once that happens, it's game over.
They're going to keep the gun.
Yeah, they're going to.
Well, you don't know for sure, right? So if somebody knows.
So, but anyways, I get up there, and this was before I got TSA pre-check, which, by the way, I highly recommend. They were like, look, you can take it back to the car, or we can keep it. I'm like, man, this is a good one.
Yeah.
This is a good one. So, like, I had to make a decision.
You didn't have time.
And so the decision was, I look at the line, and I'm like, nope, just going to go buy a new one. And so this guy got my knife.
Yep.
It's on the streets now.
The guy's making $265,000 a year, and yet he feels the need to want to
make. I don't know why you keep bringing that up.
That's good money.
You keep bringing that up.
In other words, risk versus return. You're making enough money to be happy. Why risk it all?
Because he wants more money.
He wants a little bit more money.
But my question, though, is where do they go, though? Like, where are they supposed to go? Like, when they
confiscate. That's a good question. That's
when
good
they
question,
confiscate that stuff, do you call LRPD to come take it and put it in evidence?
Maybe somebody can let us know that.
Where's it supposed to go?
Well, it was crazier, RJ.
Because I would rather it be sold back out.
Yeah,
you know,
right. I got you.
The right way.
Right.
With the background check and everything.
What do you do with a used gun? They melt it down? They smelt it?
Well, like pawn shops have used guns, right? And so
somebody's got to do some of those guns.
But this guy.
Check out serial number, see if all those things.
Yeah, this guy was not, he was just selling them, and there was no background checks or anything like that.
And apparently he was also, according to the story I saw, he was allowing people to get through without going through TSA,
oh, really?
Apparently so.
Oh, really?
Say it again? What?
Apparently, he was allowing people to go through without having to go through the checkpoints.
Oh, really?
Apparently. With a weapon?
I don't know about a weapon, but he was just bypassing somehow.
Like, he's your buddy. Like, hey, Rod, come over here.
I got you. You know, again, you can't do it even though you may have that power to work around. Yeah.
Well, if he's your buddy, don't you know, what do you got a buddy for then?
Follow,
You know, let me go if I'm your buddy.
The other part of that, too, RJ, is that he opens fire back at the ATF agents. Dude, first of all, you're caught. You don't make it worse. Turn yourself in.
So he used somebody else's gun to fire at him.
Yeah, again,
pucker, what a butt pucker he had.
Oh yeah, I don't know if he was in critical condition. And of course, he shot the ATF agent.
I know it.
Yeah, which is
instant jail time.
Anyway, a crazy story. The other one, did you hear about?
That was in West Little Rock, right?
Yes. Yeah. RJ, you and I used to hang out. We used to go out occasionally when you were younger and not married.
Did that quite a bit. Actually.
So did you hear? I wanted to ask you the spring break story. Did you hear about that?
I heard about this.
So if you would be single and down on spring break, would you be game?
No, I would not. I don't like for anybody to get in my facial area, right? Like,
what if she,
like,
if she was feeding you a
I
shot?
No, I don't like that.
You don't like that?
I don't like close talkers. I don't like even at our wedding when you combined arms and you're supposed to feed each other the cake. I wasn't even really down with that.
Even Brianna.
Yeah, like I'm just not. I don't like anybody in this area, right? Like,
so and, noted.
And so when I hear this, and I'm like, you're paying somebody not only to feed you the shot, but then to smack you after it's over with. Now I'm out.
And splash you with water in the face. Roger.
Yeah, no, I'm out.
Roger, the other day at Oaklawn, there was a close talker that got up to me, and I was like, dude, you are up in my grill. He was older, and I didn't want to say anything, but I was like, dude, I'm going to have to push you in here in a minute.
Do close talkers not realize that they're that close?
I don't think they do. I think they like getting in the space.
I think they have it's like people that like to smell asparagus urine. Well, there's just a weirdness about
I had a client the other day, or potential client, and so we wanted to meet, and he was a close, like he got like right up in, and
right?
You know, potential client. I'm like, yeah, I'm just fighting through this thing, and then we decided not to work with me or whatever. But like I'm like, what in the world? Like, do you not know there's a barrier?
I don't know how does that girl even get to that point where she comes up with that thinking that I'm going to be able to.
It's a girl.
Slap some. It's a girl.
I thought you said. Oh, I thought you were talking about the close talk.
How did the girl even come up and think? I think I can get guys to give me 30 bucks to slap them.
Something on
because
here.
It, basically one day she was like sitting at the bar with some guys and she goes, "Hey, how much would you pay me to slap you?" Well, I'll pay you 30 bucks, honey. And
what it is it is for a guy that maybe it's attention. It's a woman touching, even though it's a slap. It is a engagement.
There's swipe a booty apps for people
for whips, whips and chains.
Sure.
I'm just saying. You
get it to me. Give it all. Too much of a pause. I got to have that audio.
By the way, I do want to apologize to Daryl and to Mary. I did not see the call board.
Let's just see that.
Daryl, I'll answer it.
Questions for Craig.
No. They're gone.
We were
okay,
so enamored with Craig, we didn't look at the call board. So anyway, I just didn't
know. Somebody on here said something about it, but it was that. And so, correct me if I'm wrong, maybe you saw it on there, that it all started with a guy who was proposing somebody.
It
started out as proposal. I don't know. And I was just Ron Burgundy and what it had on here. So I
does
don't
it
know.
Say how much she makes, like,
$30
well, overall?
No, she
like, how much she's made this?
Well, you already know the drinks are probably, they're already overpriced to begin with.
That's right, But the slap is enough of a slap to... it's not like. And I told Josh, I said, "Listen, wow, you did that very."
Done that before, haven't you?
I was about to say, RJ looked very comfortable doing that.
Very comfortable doing it. Did Brianna just in her car go? Ow.
No,
RJ.
I don't know. I'm asking.
I told Josh. I said, "There's a big difference between getting slapped in the face by a happy woman versus a mad woman."
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
How many times have you been slapped?
By both a happy and a mad.
I can't imagine getting slapped in the face by a happy woman.
Well, that's what this is. That's what I'm saying. That's what this is.
How many times have a mad female
know if I've been
slapped
in the face. No, you get slapped in the face.
I've had a woman stick
her
finger in my mouth.
Yeah, I mean,
yeah.
What'd you say?
Stick her finger in your mouth.
It's the craziest thing ever. This girl and I were doing drinks. I was out in the public, in a downtown restaurant, and we were getting into it. And obviously, she probably had too much, and she comes over, and I see her.
You didn't know her?
Yeah, I did.
Oh.
I see her with her finger coming out. I'm like, where's that finger going? And she, in my mouth. I said, you just put your finger in my mouth?
I am so going to do that. when you least expect it. I am so going to do that to you.
Don't you put your finger in my mouth.
So wow. First of all, you know where my hands have been.
That was over with after that.
Well, I would hope so.
Like, you know, nobody put your finger in my mouth unless I'm asking for it.
Yeah. Keep your GED fingers out my mouth.
I was going to ask you. You've got through with basketball.
Yes, we're done.
So high school sports. You got spring football coming up.
No, I got baseball, softball championships.
That's right, you got baseball,
yeah,
softball.
So the buzz doesn't carry those games, but I will be on there with Wes Moore and Bobby Swofford, and we will be doing all the baseball and softball championships from Conway this year.
Now, when does that happen?
That'll be in May.
Oh, now, you got to remind us. I'd like to watch some.
Yeah. Now, RJ, Roger had mentioned, you know, we're really excited about having Peyton Stovall. He was on with us yesterday. Was very, very good. And we've got Will McIntyre Thursday. Mm-hmm. And you've got a little bit of a connection, right?
So that, you know, remember that clip that Roger played, the Slam-a-ram-a-roo, was when I was doing Traveler Games, right? Well, at the time, Madison, Will's dad, was the official scorekeeper for the Travs. And Will was just like a little guy. I mean, Will was probably 7, 8 years old when we were doing the games, and he was in the press box just running around.
Yeah, how about that?
And so, like, he was tiny, and then I didn't see him for probably 5 or 6 years, and the next time I saw him, he was as big as me.
Yeah, he looks almost like a football player.
Yeah, and so his family lives in Bryant. I should have taken that sponsorship down for Will, but I didn't. maybe we can go Havsy or something like that. He's a great kid, man. He's
tearing it up.
He's you know, I was hearing you, Raj, talk about he does for every strikeout. He gives money to Cartai. His dad had cancer.
Ah, gotcha.
And so that's one thing that he's very passionate about is giving money to Cartai. And you can also, if you go to Will's Twitter and Instagram pages in the profile, there's a link that you can also match Will's funds for that. And so
it's strikeout for a cause is what it is. So,
yeah, and I think you
good
can,
for him.
I think right now for every strikeout with the people that have gotten involved, I think it's like $46 a strikeout that's going back to Cartai.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So.
Well, listen, he, along with the rest of the darn pitching staff of the Razorbacks, are almost on a record pace for strikeouts. I don't know if they can sustain that. Coming up here in just a minute, we'll visit with Hannah Gamble. And if you're more than welcome to hang around, too, RJ, if you got the time.
How about that?
Extra time.
Hannah Gamble has 7 homers, and we were talking about her nickname. Have you heard any of the
Hannah Banana?
Well, because you are one of the kings of remember Slammerama
Roo. Slammerama-roo, yeah.
And so Hannah Slamma, Hannah Glam,
I think it was not Glam. I think it was Ham Gam.
Ham Gam.
I think that was even her.
Yeah, I think so.
I think her group come up with that.
So I'm just throwing it out there.
I will say this: I think of all the interviews, the spring interviews. She's probably my favorite.
She is
really good.
Yeah, she's an Arkansas girl. BD.
And she's really good. She's a really good softball player. My kid now is, Addison playing softball.
Yeah.
Arkansas Express. What? We start next week.
Are you the coach?
I'm the head coach. And so, actually, JM and I were exchanging pictures and techniques for our kids.
I like it.
And he and I are both playing in the same tournament coming up here March 30th. In
Oh, wow. That would be
JM
great.
And RJ going.
But they're
not in the same age division, but we'll be able to like watch each other and do all that.
What is your coaching uniform?
The Baz pullover thing that the coaching, I've got that with a pair of shorts. It's got Arkansas Express on the thing. We're sponsored by Under Armour, so we've got.
Are you a yelling coach? Are you pretty soft spoken?
No, I'm loud, and but it's respectful loud. Okay. Like I don't like just scream at kids.
Come on, Addy.
No, Addison, I do. But
some of them need it, RJ.
Yeah, but no, I mean we got a good little squad, and we start Tuesday, and then the first practice is Saturday. But yeah.
We'll play a little match game coming up here. I do want to thank Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse, Chris Hamlin and Donnie Faulkner for sponsoring.
Thank you, folks.
Match game. We appreciate that. Back to the Hannah deal. She's not hitting for average. She's hitting for power. 7 home runs. She's second on the team. And so, but they, I think they're on the road against Mississippi. No, they're home versus Mississippi State this weekend. RJ, it's National Proposal Day. I can't recall. How did you propose to Brianna? I cannot recall. Yeah, I know you told us on the air.
Oh, my gosh.
Refresh my memory.
We went to Mount Magazine.
Oh, my gosh. You did the whole production with the cameras and all that. Yes.
I had people hiding in the woods.
Yes,
man.
I forgot about that.
Yeah. And, we went up there, and she almost found out. She did. She, because I had the ring in my console of my truck.
Yes.
And so we were going to make a whole weekend of it. So we rented a cabin at Mount Magazine, and then I paid a photographer from Little Rock, and he got in his gully suit or the ghillie suit and got in the woods, and you couldn't see him, and so he was taking pictures.
Wow.
And then his camera died, so he didn't get the video.
No way. You've got to be. And that's what you wanted.
Because we wanted the I knew she
I
wanted
would be
the
furious.
She wanted the video and the pictures.
Dude, you have one
and
job.
We've
get
got
it right.
We've got the pictures, but we never got the video because his camera died.
I would not be. Is that somebody we know? Do we know this cameraman?
No, you don't. Huh?
Huh?
What?
The Roger. Do
hey,
you
somewhere were... before you go on, Baz. David was about to answer how many times he'd been slapped until the subject got changed. Let's go back to that for a minute. So, how many times have you slapped by a happy woman and a bad woman?
I don't think I've been slapped by an angry woman.
You have. I know. I know of one.
You do?
Yep.
I don't remember.
I'm not going to bring it up.
So the finger
Missouri.
Was a negative.
I don't think I was slapped.
No, not at Missouri. I'm just saying that.
I don't think they handcuffed her and spit bagged her. No, I don't think they slapped
but
let, me.
But then let's do this. How many times have you been slapped by a happy woman? Obviously, what this.
I haven't yet, but I think I'm intrigued by this.
Would you do this? I think it doesn't happen.
I think we're gonna do this here in Little Rock. We're gonna do this.
You're gonna do this.
Yeah, we're gonna get this started here in Little Rock.
You know who you need to let do it to you?
let her do it to you.
The old girl that is at Oaklawn that she and her husband play the guitar and
Susan.
Let Susan do it.
why is that? I don't know.
I think letting Susan slap you, that would be awesome.
Hit you, then use a car alarm on you.
There's nothing the matter with a little physical interaction. There she is.
There's nothing wrong now?
There's nothing wrong with that. A little physical play around. A little slap you there, slap you here.
Why don't we just get Jessica up here and let her? I bet she's got a lot of aggression.
RJ and Roger, why are you whispering?
Have you all been slapped by a happy woman, RJ and Roger?
I've never been slapped by a happy woman.
Let me show you.
On the face? Lean over here, Roger.
Lean over here. Let me just say, it's really easy to slap you. You know what you go?
Not on the face.
You go, that's not bad.
No, it is bad. I don't want people up in that area.
I know, we understand.
My wife says, you better, I'm up in that area all the time. I'm like, what?
Up in what area?
She's up in
my face.
Grill.
That's my wife.
That's right. Well, she's going to get in there.
You said that even on your wedding day when you were doing the cake.
You can see the pictures. Like, you know, they take the pictures and then shove them.
I'm kind of pulling back a little bit.
Yeah.
I like the fact now wherever we go for this show contamination comes up.
Good.
Contamination comes up.
I started that, Josh. And you know what?
Food contamination.
I listen to this show every day, and I hear some of the things that you guys say as far as food.
Yeah.
And in my head, I'm going,
Contamination!
I even text you guys. Like,
I think Justin even will bring it up if he recognizes it as contamination. That's what it is.
I think you guys said something about mixing some foods the other day.
Okay, well, Justin and Josh, I mean, all together, if you were a box of cereal, you would be a little bit of all that was left in individual boxes that my mom would just pour it all into one box. Here's one. How does Baz say nobody puts their finger in my mouth unless I ask for it? and we didn't say anything.
And we just glossed right over it.
I'm telling you right now, we're going to be talking to
somebody. Paying attention.
Let's say we're at Mainline this Thursday night, and we're just there, and you're talking to somebody, and I happen to be there with you. I'm going to put my finger in your mouth.
Well, you know what? We're bucks.
My fingers are good.
We're bucks.
You know what?
That's not the answer I want to hear.
That's not the answer I want to hear.
Did he just put his finger in your mouth? Yeah, it's my buddy.
I will say this. Okay, we got to hand a gamble. We got to go to the break. So last night I did something. I want to see if RJ thinks it's contamination. Roger, I went and got some 2% milk. Last week when the cereal man brought cereal, I've got connected back on cereal.
Do you have the little cereal thing? Do you have your fruit shop?
I've got the regular cereal boxes.
What kind of cereal is it?
Okay, that's what I'm going to say.
Okay.
I started with Frosted Flakes.
Have you been purchasing these?
I just did. I know where this is going.
Okay, so I finished that bowl, and there was still milk and some few flakes at the bottom. I go Fruit Loops on top of the bowl that I've just ate the Frosted Flakes out of.
Oh,
absolutely. No, absolutely not.
So that's contamination.
Listen, I will take the magic dust that is all that's left in the bottom of the box.
Yes.
Even in the Fruit Loops. Put that in the milk and slurp.
Have you guys, Josh, do you drink the milk?
Not normally, no.
No, not ever.
Yeah. Are we still talking about cereal?
All right, Hannah Gamble up next. Our extended time with RJ.
Yes!
Brought to you by Floyd Seafood, Keel Avenue in Sherwood. It's crawfish season, and Floyd's has live Louisiana crawfish. Order by 1 p.m. Thursday for weekend boils. Floyd's, meatandseafood.com.
This is SportsCenter.
March Madness officially began last night with a pair of games at the First Four in Dayton. In the West region, it was 16 seed Wagner over 16 seed Howard, 71-68. Wagner will now take on North Carolina, who's the number one seed in the West. And then in the Midwest, it was Colorado State 67, UVA 42. The Rams will now take on number 7 seed Texas on Thursday. Two more games coming tonight in Dayton. First, it's Grambling in Montana State at 5:40 on True TV. Then at 8:10, it'll be 10 seed Colorado and number 10 seed Boise State. The first round will begin officially on Thursday. I'm Josh Neighbors for the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Continuing to warm up across Arkansas, 75 today, mostly sunny. Could be a couple of showers or thunderstorms in North Arkansas, and tonight's low drops down to 50. Better rain chances statewide arriving for Thursday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
I am an athlete.
I am an educator.
I'm an EMT.
A neurologist.
A veteran.
A business owner.
I'm a mom.
We are survivors.
Cardiovascular disease is the number one killer of women and doesn't discriminate.
It can affect any woman at any age or stage.
Yet many women don't know it's our greatest health threat.
Encourage three women you love to learn more about their risk factors and how they can take charge of their health today.
Roger Scott for the Carpet Barn. The question was asked of me, does the Carpet Barn have other flooring? I responded, well, of course they do. They have a wide selection of hardwood, tile, stone, vinyl, and luxury vinyl plank, or LVP, if you will. But think about it. The name would have to be the Carpet, Hardwood, Laminate, Tile, Stone, Luxury Vinyl Barn that does backsplashes and custom showers. And that's too long. You see why the name is the Carpet Barn, your flooring specialist since 1968. The Carpet Barn will complete the process from the complimentary measures and stay with you every step of the way from selection to installation. Flooring for today and beyond. The Carpet Barn, with locations in North Little Rock on Maumelle Boulevard and in Conway on Oak Street. Both Carpet Barn stores open on Saturday by appointment. The Carpet Barn, flooring specialist since 1968. Check them out and get a head start by doing that at thecarpetbarn.net.
Red tape. One in three businesses will get caught up in it, and they'll be penalized by the IRS for mismanaging their payroll. Because when you're handling payroll, HR compliance, and those constantly changing tax laws, that red tape can get sticky in a hurry. At The Payroll Company, we free you from that tangled mess and get you back to business. The Payroll Company. Less headaches, more than payroll. Visit morethanpayroll.com to learn more.
On March 30th, one lucky Saracen casino player will win a Corvette Stingray from Guatney Chevrolet. This new Corvette is the pinnacle of precision, and with 500 horses in 0 to 60 in under 3 seconds, you'll have more speed than you'll ever need. You can win the most powerful production Stingray in history just for playing, but only at Saracen Casino Resort. Start playing today.
Saracen Casino Resort, Vegas, Arkansas style.
Gambling problem? Call 800-522-4700.
Hey, everybody, this is NFL Hall of Famer Dan Hampton, and I love hanging out with Paz and the boys on The Buzz. Tune in every morning so you can get the news just like I do.
Whips and chains.
Shoot!
I'm just saying.
A man of many talents. Play-by-play broadcast.
We hadn't played it yet.
Real estate agent.
We got Hannah. I'm sorry.
It's time to talk all things Arkansas with
RJ.
Presented by Natural State Jose. Proudly trusted by major manufacturers all over the world for 25 years. Go see the Flooring King. She's an Arkansas native and a standout for Razorbacks softball.
Going back and left, and that is gone. Hannah Gammel with the two-run home run.
She's one of the best defensive players in the country.
Down the left field side, and Gammel, great diving catch in foul territory.
Brought to you by UAMS Health Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. UAMS Health, the official orthopedics and sports medicine provider for Razorback Athletics. Joining Morning Mayhem, it's Hannah Gammel.
Good morning, Hannah. How are you this morning?
Good morning. I'm good. How are you?
Good. I was looking at your magazine. That's why I stumbled a little bit. Your magazine cover. I told the guys this morning that you were on the cover of Hogs Illustrated for this month. And this is what it says, y'all. It says, the Hannah Gammel Effect, Arkansas softball star, a difference maker in the program and community. So I can't wait to read the article. I've got an article about me in there, and I've made the comment nobody cares about old 53, but they care about what Hannah's doing. I got to say, I know this is, I was sort of the same way when I was up there. It was really important to me, Hannah, to be involved in the community and, in addition to being a Razorback athlete. I know that's really been a big, important staple of your career up there as well.
Yeah. you know, I think part of that is just coming from a town that didn't have a whole lot of resources, you know, within social work and having my internships. I think that I've seen the importance of giving human beings resources and things that they're are either going well or things that they're struggling in. And so, you know, also being a Razorback athlete, I think we pride ourselves in, you know, making a difference in the community because, again, like, people aren't going to remember necessarily, like, how you performed on the court or the floor or the field, but the impact that you made on their life. And so I think that that's been super important in my 4 years here.
Let's talk about this past weekend against Auburn. Another home run, so that's seven on the season. Obviously, that's more than what you had all last year through this. It's only 29 games so far this year. You're not hitting for average probably as much as you want to hit, but you are certainly hitting for power. You know, I know one of the things you've talked about is your mental approach and not letting things bother you. Talk about that, you know, how the power is there, but maybe not the average so far in the season.
Yeah, for sure. You know, I think that obviously hitting for average for me is more important than hitting home runs. But, you know, I think it, like last year I was hitting, you know, I hit six home runs on the entire season. Yep. And, you know, we're not even halfway through and I've hit seven. And so I think when I know that my power is there, I feel really confident where I am. And so I think it's just continuing to let loose, but also, you know, we've played in some windy weather and, you know, I think that that has kind of affected some of the hits. But what's hard is, you know, you can dribble a ball down the line that maybe gets caught, you know, I can hit a little bloop over the third base, but if I hit a line drive right at the third baseman, it's like, you know, that's kind of the hard part. So I feel confident where I am. I feel like I'm hitting the ball really hard. I think some of it's just going right to people. So, you know, I've had to just keep reminding myself that it'll fall and, hopefully I will continue to push this team to get to the World Series. I think that's the main goal is just to continue to be that spark for the team.
No question. We're visiting with Hannah Gamble, brought to you by UAMS Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Yeah, let's talk real quick, too, about Auburn. I don't know if you guys heard the story, but Bree Ellis, who was from Auburn, transferred from Auburn, they go back to Auburn, and she hit 700 this weekend. Just absolutely.
In your face.
Absolutely kills it. I'm sure, to Auburn, that had to be just, a slap in the face for sure. You had her, and then, of course, Kennedy Miller, who was a freshman of the week. And by the way, Bree Ellis, back-to-back SEC Player of the Week. First time I think that's ever happened in program history. But Kennedy Miller, as a freshman, Hannah, hitting 445. I mean, it's pretty crazy. Talk about both of those players.
Yeah. So I'll start with Bree. I was just so happy for her. You know, you can imagine how hard it is going back to where you committed and where you played for 2 years. And going back to that, whether it's good or bad, was super intimidating and hard. But she just popped off. I'm so happy for her. You know, she deserves it. She deserves to just play free and enjoy the moment that she's in, and she's definitely doing that. Kennedy Miller is just freaking insane. A freshman hitting, like, whatever number you said is just awesome. So I'm really happy for her. She's been adjusting really well, and she's just enjoying where she is, too. So, you know, you can also see how hard it is for a freshman being away and just kind of getting used to things, but she hasn't let that faze her at all. So really happy for both of them.
Razorbacks are 23-6. You'll play Mississippi State at home. So what's the temperature up there right now? You know, today's the first full day of spring, but yesterday it was 34 degrees here. What was it up there, Hannah? Probably even colder?
Yesterday it got up to 65.
Okay.
Yeah.
I was about to say, do you mind?
They're supposed to get to like 75 here today.
Yeah. Do you mind playing in cold weather softball, or do you hate it?
I don't mind it. I would rather be sweating, dripping sweat than playing in cold weather. But, you know, if it means us playing, then I would rather play in cold weather than ever play in rain. So,
wanted to ask you because I just brought it up. I was eating cereal the other night. Are you a cereal? Do you like cereal? You know, not. I don't know. When we were growing up, we old guys, we used to cereal was a regular staple. But I don't know about the kids' day. What about you? Are you a cereal person or not?
I will eat cereal. However, I cannot tell you the last time that I ate it.
Okay, so Roger, that is what's wrong with our country. We've lost Anna and others.
Anna, honestly.
They're not eating cereal. Yeah.
Even if it's Apple Jacks. You've got to eat a cereal. You've got to tip a bowl, Hannah.
Do you know what tipping a bowl is, Hannah?
Do I know what is?
Tipping a bowl of milk after cereal.
Nope. That's
the one
good
time.
It's a good thing.
Listen, yeah. Here's what you do,
half
Hannah.
Of us don't like it, half of us do.
It's a good thing you don't know that, Hannah.
Hannah, when you're through with your cereal, whatever it may be, you grab the bowl with both hands. You put your pinky in the air because we've got class. And then you sip the milk from the bowl.
You drink the milk with the remaining
right off of the
crumbs
bowl.
Of the cereal
and
in the bowl.
If you're lucky, you'll get a little bit of milk on your chin.
So RJ and I think that's contamination because you see little particles of the cereal.
You see stuff in the white milk. Yeah. And you don't, it's like, no, I'm out.
But it may not matter to Hannah because she doesn't do cereal at all. Sure, your mom and dad never had you eat cereal as a little girl? Maybe that's a guy thing.
Yes, they fed me Honey Nut Cheerios.
Okay, there we go.
Honey Nut Cheerios.
There we go. Well, that's just for making sure. Well, I'm sure you eat perfect now. Yeah. What's your breakfast of choice now?
Yeah, what are you eating? Cauliflower?
I would say a protein shake and egg.
Protein shake and eggs. Listen, of course you. We had Peyton Stovall on yesterday. We've got Peyton and Will McIntyre, and we asked Peyton yesterday. He had remember what his pregame meal was?
Yeah, I couldn't understand it.
It was Subway. He said he always made Subway.
I didn't catch it.
What about Hannah Gamma? What is your pregame? Do you have something every game?
Yeah.
Every day you have a game, you eat something particular?
Yep. Every time we're at home, I have tropical smoothie before.
Okay.
Chicken pesto, flatbread, no tomatoes, extra mozzarella cheese, salt and vinegar chips. And a peanut butter cup smoothie.
Okay, I want you to say that because you went through that so fast.
Yeah.
It was a little muffled.
Break it down.
So you said tropical smoothie. Give us the sandwich again.
Chicken pesto flatbread with no tomatoes, with extra mozzarella cheese and salt and vinegar chips, and then a peanut butter cup smoothie.
Know what? That sandwich with those salt and vinegar chips sounds so awesome. If you've got a cut on the outside of your mouth, and you eat those chips, it's over.
I had the peanut butter cup smoothie the other day.
Yeah, that's good, isn't it?
It is really good.
That's good. And the sandwich is a tropical smoothie.
I thought originally I was like, contamination. Then I was like, you know what? We're going to try it. And it was really, really good.
Well, of course, you know, my next point, guys, because of the world we live in, do you have an NIL deal with tropical smoothie?
Oh, I wish. You know, I should try that. I should try to go get one.
Let your agent, David Basil, let me make a phone call up there. Because if you're there every day, they know who you are. You come in.
You should be getting free food.
That's the Hannah special.
Hello. And then every little girl sees what Hannah's eating, and they want to hit dingers too.
Yeah.
That's right. I'm going to call him today.
Yeah, yes. We need to get that done. I do want to thank UAMS, Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, for sponsoring Hannah. Hannah, listen, whip those Mississippi State balls. Yeah, what's up, Roger?
I want to ask her if she received her package.
Oh, that's right. Did you get your Morning Mayhem sweatshirt yet?
I did. I received the sweatshirt. I wore it yesterday to go eat in.
Awesome.
Thank you. If you don't mind,
will you wear it again, take a photo, and send it to Baz, and if it's okay with you, may we post it?
Yep.
Please do that. Thank you to
RJ,
Steve Qualls
Steve.
Design Lab in Hot Springs.
Yeah, he sent that. Last year we got Hannah the jewelry.
I know she got
Jones's
earrings, right?
Yes. And so give her sweat. Well, listen, we're doing our best, Hannah.
We're doing what we can. You're our fave,
you guys are
Hannah.
Awesome.
Yeah. Listen, would you please clap us out before you go?
Yep. Two claps and a
two. Thanks, Anna. Talk to you next week.
She's out. There it is, right there.
Perfect.
We're so weird.
Go ahead and give us that.
let's take a break.
Let's take a break.
We got to play Mass Game when we come back.
Extended time.
We need a contestant. Josh, what do we have to play for today? We should have some good things today. We should have some good
items. What do you got?
A 20-pound bag of Hornet ice.
What?
No, he's still looking. We'll take the break.
Keep looking.
661, I'm sure it's an amazing prize.
It's going to be Hornet ice.
Don't forget to go to the Buzz website to get the bracket information to fill out our bracket. Now, if you got Safari, you may not see our bracket. We got to get that fixed.
Can't see it on Safari?
I can't see it on mine.
Rowdy Hall pickleball tickets.
Rowdy Hall pickleball tickets.
What does that do?
$25 gift certificate.
The $25 gift certificate.
Boom. Yeah. Very nice. Boom. 661-1037.
is the time of year to enjoy life. Stop letting that pain in your joints keep you from doing what you want to do this spring. Call QC Kinetics now. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. I'm talking about lasting joint relief with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. Hey everybody, it's RJ Hawk. It's a fact. QC Kinetics is literally transforming lives. Their advanced treatments harness your own body's ability to restore and repair damaged joint tissue. Pro athletes have been doing this for decades, but now this life-changing treatment is available to you so you can walk and run and climb stairs and play golf and just move again, all pain-free. No pain pills, no risky surgery. This is an all-natural solution. QC Kinetics has tens of thousands of satisfied patients and people right here in Central Arkansas. Call QC Kinetics for that free consultation. 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440.
The king of Arkansas sports talk, Randy Rainwater for Bet Saracen.
In Arkansas, 7 out of every $10 placed on a sporting bet app is with Bet Saracen, because Bet Saracen offers more ways to win and more ways to get paid and faster. Find your winners on Bet Saracen and look for my double R prop bet specials. I pick them and you win them.
Bet Saracen is Arkansas's favorite sports wagering app.
Gambling problem? Call 800-522-4700.
The all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock are opening March 27th. Over 100,000 square feet of hardware, outdoor appliances, a window and door center, and even a drive-through lumber yard. And there's nothing like Design One. This stunning showroom is one place for all your home and design needs, including 12 full kitchens and 9 baths, plus a huge selection of lighting, flooring, countertops, and more at the all-new Lumber One and Design One in West Little Rock.
Hey, this is Mitch at Red River Ford and Cabot, and we need your help because we've got the trucks.
And even more trucks.
And even more trucks.
Let your friends know that Red River Ford and Cabot has 1.9% interest for 72 months and up to over $8,000 off Ford F-150s. And we've got the trucks.
So come check us out at Exit 19 in Cabot.
Or you can visit us online at redriverfordcabot.com.
Our care clinics are your hometown source for primary medical care. Our doctors, nurses, and counselors can help patients of all ages with anything from common colds and immunizations to depression, anxiety, and chronic diseases. Our network includes both mail order and local pharmacies to fulfill your prescriptions. If you don't have insurance, it's okay. We can help with that too. And no one is turned away. With more than 65 locations in Arkansas, there's a good chance we're in your hometown. Look us up at ourcare.net.
The Avett Brothers are coming to Little Rock September 17th at First Security Amphitheater. Tickets are on sale Friday at 10 a.m. at Ticketmaster.com. Make plans now for an evening with the Avett Brothers, September 17th at First Security Amphitheater. Get tickets this Friday.
Tackle your outdoor projects with Greenway Equipment's Lawn Patrol Package. Handling is effortless with the John Deere 1023E's Twin Touch Foot Controls with a hydrostatic transmission and four-wheel drive with power steering. The 60D Driveover Auto Connect Belly Mower makes mowing easy. And the 120R Quick Park Loader is perfect for dirt moving and mulching projects. With 0% APR for 84 months and a 6-year powertrain warranty, it's a deal you can't miss. For more information, head to your local Greenway or visit gogreenway.com. With approved credit, see dealer for details.
It's the Average Guy Movie Review, Thursdays in the Zone with Justin and DJ, presented by Rock and Roll Sushi. The guys will recap or look ahead to what's trending on TV, the big screen, Netflix, or however you receive your TV service. Presented by Rock and Roll Sushi, deliciously twisted flavors and a rock and roll vibe that will blow your mind. RockandRollSushi.com.
Can you hear Justin Moore's smoke alarm every 10 minutes? If you can, text our Southern Structural Solutions text line at 501-661-1037.
It's time to play the match game.
Yeah!
Brought the match to you game. By Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse, Arkansas's truck accessory headquarters for over 30 years. Call 501-568-0040 today or check online at arkansastruck.com. Now, let's see what wacky answers the guys can come up with.
That's right. Let's do it. Rick, are you going to play match game?
I am.
Fantastic. You'll be playing for a $25 gift certificate to
Rowdy Hog.
Rowdy Hog.
Pickleball.
Pickleball. Yeah, very good.
I got a chance. RJ got a chance to tell Roger to go out there to the outlet mall.
Yeah.
They're getting ready to install courts.
At the outlets?
They do. They're getting ready. You ought to see the setup they have.
Pickleball Rowdy has purchased a couple of buildings, so yeah, they put them inside.
They've got their store where you get all the rackets and things, but then they got where you can actually play. But
how about
James,
that? How about
James
that?
And Jolene cool. Hart, nice people, and they got. He's all tatted up with Razorback stuff, which I have great respect for.
Have you driven by, speaking of the alleys, have you driven by and seen the giant bouncy house maze?
Yes. Kids go crazy when
they see
that.
No, it's for adults, too.
Stop it.
No, so I went out there the other day. I didn't do it. But they were like, yeah, this is for adults and kids. It's a big maze.
I think of the movie where the girl who had the movie with Matthew McConaughey here in Arkansas.
Yeah, Mud.
Mud, the girl who starred in that.
Yeah, Reese Witherspoon.
Reese Witherspoon was in a movie about a bouncy house where she, as a kid, got trapped in there.
Yeah that's right.
It was with
that's Four Christmases.
Four Christmases, yeah, that scene is so good.
It's very good.
Rick, are you ready to play?
I'm ready.
All right, good
You've
luck,
got
Rick.
The great RJ Hawk
here
in studio, but brought to you by Natural State
Natural
Wholesale.
State Wholesale. If you would like flooring, Rick, you can go to naturalstatewholesale.com.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
It is National Astrology Day. I really haven't spent much time on that. So we're going to go star blank.
Star?
Star blank. Give us a chance to get our answer first. Josh, are you in? Are you, all right, Roger, you got your answer?
I do.
RJ, you good?
I'm good.
All right, what do you have, Rick?
Got to be wars.
Star Wars. You know,
Star
Wars.
Very good answer.
A lot of different directions.
A lot of different answers.
I think of Bill Murray. Star Wars.
Nothing but Star Wars. Roaming through the galaxy with nothing to do.
We'll go to our guest, RJ Hawk. RJ, Star what?
I went Star Search.
Search.
Oh, my gosh. I didn't even have that.
I didn't either.
Josh, what did you have?
Star Spangled Banner.
Star Spangled Banner.
Gosh.
Why not? Of course, of course.
Raj, what did you have?
I went Guardians of the Galaxy. I went Star Lord.
Oh my gosh, Star Lord.
Yeah.
You know, there were so many different directions.
Come on, Basil.
You go,
give us some that you want.
You could go Starship.
Yep.
Yeah.
You could go Star Power.
You could.
You could go Star Trek.
You could go Star
obviously.
Trek.
Obviously.
But you know what? If you want to have a winner, you go Star Wars.
Yeah!
That's what happened.
How you do it right there.
That's what it is.
That's exactly right.
I don't even think Basil's ever watched Star Wars, but
I know. It's not my favorite.
You know what? We've got a lot of those. Can we give another one away?
You bet.
Can we do it again? All right. Josh, get Rick's information. What's that?
I'll take two, Roger.
Well, you hold on to that. We're going to send somebody else there with you, Rick. Hold on. Let's do it one more time. 661-1037. 661-1037.
Yeah, RJ, have you played pickleball yet?
I've played one time.
Yeah, Roger and I did last year. I had no idea.
Remember, I came with you over to the Little Rock Athletic Club
for
event.
For the state championship.
Yeah.
Over at Rowdy Hog Pickleball, rackets are different kind. You know, the words you can go wide for more of a sweet spot, thinner for more power and speed.
Yes.
JM. Anyway, who knew? But yeah, the word is apparently kids are playing more of it now. The kids.
That's good.
Hey, the three of us, let's go play pickleball this afternoon at Rowdy Hog. The three of us.
No, they're still working on that. They
okay, then let's go somewhere and play.
Yes,
I got a spot in Bryant. We can go.
They get.
Where is
that?
Yeah, we got a whole
where
over at Mills Park.
See, the challenge
pickleball?
Is they don't have many indoor. That's why Rowdy Hog's doing that.
River Center in Benton has.
They do.
Yeah.
And then you got Little Rock Athletic Club just opened a multi-million-dollar
Samantha!
Place.
Where's the Mills Park?
And let's not forget Summerwood
661-1037.
Summerwood Sports does in indoor pickleball.
They do pickleball.
They do right there. Yeah. You have to do that.
What happens is you have people fighting for those spaces, whether it be basketball, tennis, and then. That's why at Rowdy Hog, they're dedicated to that. And, of course, at the Little Rock Athletic Club, it's dedicated as well.
So this afternoon, the three of us, we're going to go play a little pickleball. Come on.
I think I have to work today.
You got nothing.
You got nothing.
Put a finger in your mouth.
When does the session start, the new session?
April 10th.
Wow. So is that like spring session? Is that what
this
is?
No, it's called the fiscal session.
Fiscal session.
And we will be in session for 30 days. Just talking budgets. And,
I look for
money.
Your name on the list where you get reimbursed for all your travel.
I'm always at the bottom.
Yeah.
You notice that?
Yeah. Some guys at the top are like $45,000 or $80,000.
I intentionally do that. I don't.
Well, you're close. You should have too far.
I don't sign into meetings because I don't feel that my short little drive from Bryant to the Capitol deserves the per diem.
Right.
And so now if I'm going to be down here all day. We may do that, but if it's just for a single meeting, I don't sign into the per diem box.
You were on the technology commission. a committee. Is that right?
Oh, how did you know that?
How about that?
How did you know that?
I do my research.
Oh, really?
My
yes. That was was a speaker appointed position.
Yeah, Geo Fenson.
Yes, I am on that committee.
So you're weighing in on TikTok. You're doing all those kind of things. Are you from the state of Arkansas technology?
The TikTok thing is more of a Tom Cotton technology committee.
National, yeah.
Way to go, Tom.
We don't really do that. We really work with.
What are you doing about the border?
The GIS, nothing of it with that. But we work with the GIS system for the state of Arkansas.
Okay.
We work with cities and counties on firewalls, things like that.
How ridiculous do you think it was that Sarah Huckabee's name even came up as a VP candidate?
Did it?
Yeah,
I didn't see it.
Yeah, I heard it being rumored out there. What are those unmarked buses that I see at 4 a.m.?
What else is your what other committees are you on?
I am on the agriculture committee.
Oh, nice. That's very good. You're a farmer.
That committee is also for economic development.
Hello.
So that committee is they combine the two things.
Can we have a community garden?
So, yes, I'm on ag, and then I'm on transportation.
Very powerful. So how many more circle drives are we going to get?
And then I am the ex officio for audit.
Ex officio.
On audit.
Ex officio for audit.
Yep. So basically what that means I am the backup for the speaker on audit.
Bill Vicker was in the other day. Carlton Wing was listening. I know you know Carlton.
Oh, yeah, Carlton.
Great guy. Yeah. Got the great pipes. Oh, my gosh. You and him could combine to do the legislative radio network.
We've got the unofficially, by the way, it's the media caucus.
I know you're the voice.
We're the only two that have any media. And you know what's funny?
You're the only two voices.
He's got the TV background.
Yes,
Carlton
yes.
Wing, by the way, that's who we're talking about. And so Carlton goes over the top with everything. And so when we did our freshman orientation, they let Carlton be
What does that mean? He goes over the top.
Well, so rather than just standing down at the well and telling us how to do things. Carlton decided to make a video.
Oh, well.
It is this highly produced video of the process of taking a bill from the time that you go and fire, get it written up all the way up through the governor's office.
Yes.
And he did, it's great work.
Did that. It's called Schoolhouse Rock.
Well, Carlton, he did 2.0 on it because it's really good. He's one of my dear friends up there, and he's really good at what he does. And so,
oh, my gosh, you guys could do a play-by-play of the session. Give me
a sample.
What do you mean?
Of whatever the play-by-play would be.
The play-by-play would be.
So somebody's coming up to speak.
Somebody's coming to the well.
Yeah, somebody's coming to the well, and they're getting ready to speak on something really, really boring.
Now on the House floor, it's House Bill 33251. Coming to the well to speak is Representative Brian Evans.
Yeah! All right. Listen, give me a background on Brian. Brian Hill's from.
I think we need
yes. Hailing from Cabot, Arkansas, the future Speaker of the House of Representatives, Brian Evans, is at the well.
I think you need to do a bit.
I got a phone number I want you to call, too.
Oh, I heard about this guy.
Dude, this is incredible.
I do want to call him.
Craig would eat his lunch. It'd be so funny.
It would be funny.
What's amazing, that guy's still mad. He's been mad for years.
He really hates me for it. And
you do give your number to a lot of people, and so when you transfer that number, a lot of people hold on to that number, and so his phone probably blows up a lot.
Well, a ton of the people that have that number, and they haven't changed, were people that were wanting to talk to somebody as far as alcohol, drugs, and all that. So I gave it out to a lot of people.
Yeah.
And when we transferred, I don't know the numbers of the folks, so for that person, that guy to get those calls, he hates it, man.
Real quick, the bartender, we were asking how much she's making. Roger, you asked about the slapping guys and feeding them feeding them drinks and all that.
Yeah.
$6,000 a night.
How much?
$6,000
a night. This is what somebody says here.
She makes $6,000 a night.
Now I don't know if that's true.
Listen,
I
want to start bar. I want to slap.
No, I will slap.
I want to go to West Hollywood and start slapping.
So like my friends back home get kicked out of strip clubs and stuff like all the time.
Say it again.
My friends back home get kicked out of strip clubs and stuff. They would not do this. Even
your
friends
that get kicked out of that's how you're qualified. Your buddies that get kicked out of strip club wouldn't even do that.
Slapped in the face. It's so stupid.
But it's easy slap. It's not a heavy slap. But there's no way she's making.
What do you think? It's just a little love tap.
Right,
Hold
on. Go to your videos right now. Hold on, Joshua. Hold on. Look at Bass. Look at give me the easy slap.
I watched it. I watched it.
That was a swipe.
You watched it.
Is that a slap? It's a swipe.
Yeah. So it sounds like that.
I mean, it's
he's swiping.
That's right. It's a good slap, but it's not.
It's not like the slap it competition?
Actually, Roger, actually,
I don't want the virus. Right, now, you've Roger, done it to me.
Actually, it would probably get the juices flowing. Right. Just saying, get you started.
You pay for this?
Get you started.
You'd pay for it?
I'll just, if I was there with part of the guys, I'd say, let's go. I'd be the first. I'd jump in there.
Wow.
Yes. I would pay for it.
Listen, it's all about having fun. It's all and helping,
is
the,
not
helping
fun.
The young
it's
lady.
It's all about having fun.
Josh,
get the
maybe
juices
that's what
flowing.
You need in your life is a couple slaps to the face.
Yeah,
by
a little
girl.
Erotica in your life, man.
I'm not going to get paid.
Come on, let me slap you a little bit.
Oh, RJ, they said they need walk-up music. Now, that's funny for exactly. The legislators.
That, you know, as they're walking up to the well and you hear, like, Enter the Sandman as they're walking to the well, I'm going to see. So we're getting a new speaker right after the fiscal.
Yes.
Probably going to be Brian Evans, but that's one rule I'm going to change. Is we've got to get walk-up music when we go up there.
Thanks to Natural State Wholesale.
Thanks, Don Grisham and the guys. I'm Cabot. Yeah. NaturalStateWholesale.com.
Go to them before you go to anybody else and let them work a deal for you. They do great stuff and get great product as well. All right, it is 9 o'clock. Thank you, man. Extra time.
Thanks, guys. John. Appreciate you. Horned Ice, don't forget about it. High season's back.
I need the code.
Scott here. And yes, I know you hear me promoting many of our beloved clients on the bus, and they are all special and dear to me. So to all those clients, I say thank you. In fact, my wife thanks you as well, along with our Amazon delivery person who comes by the house every single day because of you, and we appreciate you. But let me tell you about a client that has been near and dear to my heart for over a decade. A very special client who's become a friend to me and my family over the years. In fact, they've become like family too. Yep, that's right. Of course, I'm talking about Gravely Mowers. I've been a proud Gravely Mower owner for years, and I've used everything from theirs, from a 21-inch push mower to their 72-inch commercial unit, including my favorite, the ZT Heavy Duty 60-inch. Mm-hmm. And now, it's the best time of year to get a brand new Gravely of your choice. Why, you ask? Well, how about 0% interest over 48 months? Are you interested? Sure you are. So join the Gravely family if you haven't already by stopping by at your local Gravely dealer today, like Dacus Rental in Searcy or Haynes Home Center in Morrilton.
Mark your calendars for the 20th annual Double B's BuzzBQ, Saturday, May 11th at the downtown Riverside RV Park in North Little Rock. Tickets on sale soon.
A lot of talk.
Why do you have to talk like that?
And a lot more attitude.
You have a problem? Turn off your station.
103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock. Buzz News with Channel 7's Cassandra Webb.
The executive director of the Clinton National Airport was involved in a shootout with federal agents Tuesday morning. ATF agents were performing a search warrant at 53-year-old Brian Malinowski's home in West Little Rock Tuesday morning. While serving the warrant, ATF officials say Malinowski opened fire, injuring one person. Agents fired back and injured the executive director of the airport. He and the agent were sent to the hospital for treatment. The agent had non-life-threatening injuries, while Malinowski's injuries are unknown. Many people might be concerned about their cell service when the solar eclipse happens April 8th. Cell service reps don't anticipate many issues when the eclipse happens, but there are some things to be on the lookout for. Since many are coming to Arkansas, one rep says to make sure you have the latest software downloaded on your device. And another from AT&T says when it's packed, you can move back and forth to LTE and 5G network to find internet. The networks will be monitoring the event closely. From the Channel 7 Newsroom, I'm Cassandra Webb.
For interior, exterior, commercial, and residential painting, hire the pros at Serta Pro Painters. Get your free estimate at CertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Continuing to warm up across Arkansas, 75 today, mostly sunny. Could be a couple of showers or thunderstorms in North Arkansas, and tonight's low drops down to 50. Better rain chances statewide arriving for Thursday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
Thompson Electric presents Jackson Wells each week in the Zone with Justin and DJ. Thompson Electric, since 1983, providing innovative electrical solutions for your business. To learn more, check them on the web at thompsonelectric.com, or you can search Thompson Electric on Facebook and Instagram for more information.
Man, so many great things happening right now at Oaklawn Racing Casino Resort. You have world-class horse racing from Thursday through Sunday in the month of March. And, of course, the Arkansas Derby is set for March 30th. Make sure you get your grandstand seat reservations plus hotel reservations now at Oaklawn.com. And March Madness has arrived. Oaklawn is ready to help you make money with their Oaklawn Sports app, where new customers can earn $1,000 in bonus bets. You heard me right, $1,000. All you have to do is download the Oaklawn Sports app from Apple or Google Play, create an Oaklawn Sports account, make a deposit, then make a bet. Once you deposit into Oaklawn Sports, you are automatically enrolled in the promotion. Place your first bet, and if that bet loses, you receive a bonus bet of equal value up to $100. You get to do that for 10 straight days. Oaklawn is giving you this opportunity for your first 10 days starting on the day of your initial deposit. You can fund your account by using MasterCard or Visa debit and credit cards, also PayPal, VIP, ACH, and on-site cash at the sportsbook. Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
Now's the time to get a great deal on proven Kubota farming equipment. Tractors that are adaptable, versatile, and rated number one in durability and owner experience. Hay tools that are backed by a two-year warranty. And durable Sidekick utility vehicles and SVL track loaders. Right now, bring home select Kubota equipment for zero down, 0% APR for up to 48 months, now through March 31st. Visit KubotaUSA.com for full details. Hennard Foothills Equipment, South Main Street in Searcy. Your hometown Kubota dealer, no matter where you live.
Chosen as one of Arkansas's best places to work 8 years in a row, Rainwater Holden Sexton is hiring premier paralegals and legal assistants with an emphasis on bilingual Spanish-speaking candidates at all locations. Rainwater Holden Sexton's mission is to compassionately represent injured and disabled Arkansans. With generous benefits and competitive pay, Rainwater Holden Sexton is a destination employer hiring the best. We're also seeking bilingual Spanish-speaking attorneys to join our team. Apply today at callrainwater.com.
Hello, folks. It's Frank Fletcher from the Fletcher Dodge Store here in Sherwood. For the past few months, we've been asking you to give us a chance to buy your cars, and the response has been great. We really appreciate all of you who brought your cars in and turned it into cash. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Folks, we're still buying cars every day. So look around and see what you or your family has in the garage that you want to turn into cash. It's really easy, folks. Just come into Fletcher Dodge and ask for Chris or Andy. We'll buy any vehicle and we'll pay you more than anyone. We can't find enough vehicles at the auto auctions to meet the demand, so we're extending you this offer to the public. We'll pay you more, so don't wait. We've purchased hundreds of cars from fine people just like you. Come see us today for the best cash offer on your car, truck, van, or SUV. Just ask for Chris or Andy. We'll pay you more, so come see us at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood. Thanks.
Old Man Winter here. One more snowstorm.
Not a chance, Mr. Winter. It's spring.
It's also time for the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event, where you can get great deals on all our award-winning Hyundai models, all backed by America's Best Warranty. Hurry in. These deals won't last at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now get 0% APR on the Tucson or pay only $369 a month with zero down payment. Now, during the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Offers end soon. Call 469-613-0227 for details.
Hey, it's Craig O'Neill. I want to share with you recently a letter that I saw from a woman who moved to Arkansas in 73, fell in love with Pettie Jean Meats. Whenever she goes home to Indiana, no matter the occasion, she always has to bring Pettie Jean Meats because they absolutely love it. And not just the ham. It can be the hot dogs, the hot links, the bologna, whatever. Why wouldn't a family fall in love with it? It's a family that produces it, now in its fourth generation of Pettie Jean Meats. You will taste the difference.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem.
I want your blood. I want your soul.
Live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios.
And I want them both right now.
Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
I'm your huckleberry.
Here is David Basil, Roger Scott, and Justin Moore.
All right, longer. Let's do it.
Let's do it longer. 9:06 here on Morning Mayhem. We appreciate you listening so much on this first full official day of spring. It is the spring equinox and the March equinox.
They're jamming. It's like peanut butter and jelly, man.
Yeah, I don't know how they do
it's
both.
It's peanut butter and chocolate.
I don't know how they do both, but they do it.
Yeah.
I've had a fun show today. Craig O'Neill brought to you by Pettie Jean Meats. Outstanding Craig, RJ Hawk, Natural State Wholesale, and Anna Gamble, UAMS, Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. All three, a lot of fun. But we had to check in with our buddy. I do want to thank Pickup Truck Accessory Warehouse for sponsoring Match
Game. Thank you, Pickup.
Let's check in with our man, Double R, Randy Rainwater. Good morning, Double R. How are you? Did we lose him? We must have lost him. Dad, I mean, he was right there a second ago.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Can you get him back on the phone? We had him there just for a second. Lost him. Trey Cochran joins us now.
Hey, Trey.
Trey, good morning. You probably did not know you were going to be on air, but here you are.
No.
So don't get nervous. Here we go. You're a sophomore at Catholic, right?
Yeah. Yes.
First of all, congratulations for getting out of class. Well done.
Smart play. Initiative.
Yes.
Yes.
Are you? Unless you're not supposed to be
here. I have spring break right now.
Okay, very nice. Okay,
you're good. Very good. Very good.
Do you have a girlfriend?
No.
Good.
No, sir.
You're on the way.
Well, then stop talking to him about slapping.
Your dad is the new football coach at Catholic. So if I'm not mistaken, he's been a longtime English teacher.
Yes, sir.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, how about that?
He said new. You sounded like you said new.
You better get your hanging participles right, young man. You're right.
Hanging participles.
That's exactly right. And your mom is at Buckside.
Yes.
She's a teacher. Wow.
Buckside.
Listen, you have no room for failure in academics.
Really listen. Yeah, you need some fun.
Yes. Thanks. Are you going to be shadowing this week?
Yes, sir. Yeah. At least for today.
Are you shadowing Josh or us or the station?
The zone.
What happened?
Yes.
Yeah, very nice. So the zone, we're just sort of an over. You just got here early?
Part of it.
The fun show, Trey.
Yeah.
We're the fun show.
Here's what's going to happen.
Just make sure you don't get blood on you from Josh back
there. Yeah, his nose just starts bleeding. It's just spontaneous bleeding is what it is. You're going to be doing something later. You're going to be on zone later. Is that what it is? You'll find out. It won't be long. They're not going to be real to you.
Trey was with the final hour of the show yesterday.
Yes. Oh,
I just didn't see him because obviously
we didn't know you were here. Where were you?
Yes. I was here at the studio.
Is that in here?
Yes.
Oh, of yesterday's show.
Yes.
Not ours.
Zoo.
Oh, I didn't know that. We were at the zoo. I had no idea. It's a one-way camera.
So
very good.
Are you thinking about now? What's crazy, Roger? He's only a sophomore. So man, you're so it's sort of like Dylan Smith Wainson. You guys are so young, but you already sort of think you want to do this. And I didn't do any of this. I wish we.
So what is a sophomore? 16.
Josh,
are you 16?
I'm 16.
Let me tell you something. Can I be honest with you a minute?
Yes, sir.
I was 16, like 2-3 weeks ago. That's how fast it goes. Okay, remember that. Enjoy your life.
Let's try back in with double R. You get to sit in with a double R call. Mm-hmm. I think. Do we have him now, Rod? Just try it again.
I have to wait.
Randy Rainwater of Drive Sports. Randy, good morning.
I get it. You really don't want me on.
We do want you on.
Keep dropping me. I get it.
So what's the deal here, Randy? So here's the deal. What's going on? Listen, now you hear us giving away a thank you to Steve Qualls at Design Lab in Hot Springs, who provides all of the Morning Mayhem shirts.
T-shirts.
Gives us our hats.
Yes.
Gets us our sweatshirts, our hoodies, and all that sort of thing. So now didn't we get you a shirt? So now you want
a
hoodie or a sweatshirt? Is that what I'm hearing, Randy?
I want to be among the privilege of having a Morning Madness sweatshirt. I've got a Morning Madness T-shirt I wear proudly.
Yeah,
I wear it proudly out in the yard.
Right.
The dogs love it. The dogs love my T-shirt. My Morning Madness T-shirt. Yeah. I figured they'd go wild if I had a sweatshirt.
All right. So Steve. Steve,
Steve's listening. Steve, right
what
now,
a legend.
Steve is leaving the T-shirt business because I am costing him way too much money. He's going into selling pens, the little bitty rubber parts on the tops of pens.
What size, Randy? Are you an XL?
Oh, he's a double X, easy.
No, he is.
Oh yeah, no, I'm not. I'm not. Roger, watch your mouth.
Okay.
Just an
XL. Okay. I'm sorry. I didn't know.
So Roger got a chance to go by and see Randy and Carrie. So Randy's recovering from shoulder replacement.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So this is surgery number 38, I think, for Randy. That. And you said this is maybe one of the more tougher ones you've had, right?
Yeah, for whatever reason. Maybe it's because of my dancing age and how wonderful of a physical condition I maintain. But nah, this one's been a little bit of a booger, but that's okay. You know, every once in a while, you got to have a little bit of pain to have some success. So it's getting better every day. And I'm Dr. Kurt Reynolds, by the way, Ortho Arkansas. I don't have their number handy. I'd give it out. I've learned so much from Morning Madness how to promote and hype my clients. So I need to say it again. Dr. Kurt Reynolds, Ortho Arkansas.
We love Ortho Arkansas.
That is my shoulder replacement doctor. So
are you even wearing a shirt right now because of that?
He's naked right now.
Yeah. Are you completely nude, or do you have on a hand towel?
I'm hanging out here waiting for my sweatshirt, freezing to death because I'm thinking.
We just found out you wanted one.
We're going to get it done.
We're going to try to take care. Listen, where's my...
We had Rick on the call. We had Rick on the call on the phone yesterday. Of course, your partner. We have him on Tuesdays, and we brought up the thing about you because a lot of I got a lot of texts the other day. Randy is teeing off on Kevin, McPherson, and Rick is too. So I love it, Roger. That the Double R, even when he's got guests on that are sponsored, he will bring out the belt and do a little whipping when needed. And did you think you got your you think you got your point across, Double R?
Well, I just, you know, I feel like I have a responsibility to our listeners, all 13 of them. When you know, we feel like we've been teased, and you know, give us some meat, give us some, you know, put something on the bone. And you know, you're making statements that, you know, you got these sources, and then when you throw out the fact, well, it's out there on social media. Well, if it's on social media, then it is no longer a secret. You're keeping nothing confidential then. But anyway,
hey, Kevin's a good guy. We all like him. He's done a good job with him. I think what you said is correct. At some point, you know, you got to throw something out there with it instead of just throwing it out there. So
yes, and that coupled with the fact that you've been on a lot of meds lately probably was agitating you too because of your surgery.
Roger, if I said I was hiring a kite, then I would get myself in trouble with
you. Sure.
And angry, but you know, I was flying pretty high.
Yeah.
But anyway, I just, you know, you hear it, and then you're getting all this feedback through all of our very much legitimate social media sources.
Yes, sir.
Buzz text line, Southern Structural Solutions Buzz text line, and the LifePain feedback, by the way, is not sponsored. We need a sponsor for that. But they're always saying, come on, give us more, tell us more. And I felt like this was an area that he could tell more. If you knew that Musselman was making contact with Louisville, then if it's out there in the public domain, then all you got to do is say, okay, he looked at the Louisville or whatever it may have been, whoever the school was. But don't just say, well, my sources have made me swear to confidentiality. You know, if it eventually comes out, then I'll confess it. Then, well, yeah, it's easy to confess it after the fact. You're getting my blood pressure.
I'm sorry. I'm trying to help you.
We're going to calm you back down.
See, you did it to me, Roger.
You're welcome.
It's spring break. I was wondering if young Double R, back when you were snagging balls and getting hits at for the Little Rock Trojans, back then the UALR Trojans, did you ever do anything fun on spring break as 18-year-old Randy or 19, 20-year-old Randy?
Davey, I've got to confess to you, back in those days, we didn't have anything called a spring break.
I got you. That makes sense. I got you.
Only thing that we ever got to take off, this was back in high school, was, you know, back in November, you'd always have these teacher meetings.
Yes.
And you know, it kind of sometimes coincided with the opening of deer season. But, you know, we didn't have all these days off that these kids and college students get today. And, you know, if you got a snow day, you celebrate a snow day.
We did.
My goodness gracious.
When we were kids, our spring break consisted of me and four of my best buddies would go to Foostam and Skinny Dip.
Foostam.
Foostam. Just me and my boy.
Foostam, if we take batting practice, I'm going to tell you, Roger, here's the thing.
People thought we were weird, but we were buddies.
Here's the thing about it, Roger. I used to have to walk to school a good mile. It was always in a foot of snow. It was uphill. I never had anyone take my lunch. I always had to carry my own lunch.
That was so funny.
Hey, listen, Steve Qualls from Design Lab in Hot Springs has just sent back a text, Randy, and it's two words. got it. You're going to be getting your Morning Mayhem sweater or hoodie, whichever Steve deems necessary for you, in the extra large size. So there you go. You have it once again. Morning Mayhem delivers to you, but I have yet to see my Chris Curry Little Rock Trojan.
Yeah, that's right. We have not been taking care of it.
When you're I tell you,
boy, and the Trojans have really...
My flat bill hat is on its way to you. You and your bubble gum with your wrappers and all the other stuff and your rubber bands you wrap around the front of your hat to make that duck bill look. Yeah.
That's right.
It's a flat bill. It's a flat bill.
I'm wearing the Trojans,
the Trojans have lost some tough games recently. Hey, before I let you go, Double R, we asked Craig O'Neill today. Today is National Proposal Day, so we asked Craig what was his proposal like to Jane, and we found that he never really proposed to Jane. So what about Care? Give us the proposal. What did you do? Anything spectacular for you and Care?
Yeah, this was in the old train station in downtown Little Rock, and you know there's always that free... Arkansas Sports Hall of Fame reception.
Yes.
And I just decided that night, for some reason I was invited, which I can't understand why still this day, why, because that's the only one I've ever been to, the only one I was ever invited to. But anyway, I thought that was a perfect night to invite her, propose to her. And it was so ironic because we walked in with Joe Klein, and somehow we got our picture taken with Joe. We looked like midgets standing up next to Joe.
Yes.
But anyway, that night I decided to propose, and the rest is history. But yeah, I remember that just like it was half 5 minutes ago.
So that was the old train. She just got down on the knee in front of everybody. Did everybody see you do it?
She slap you?
No, we were, you know, it was kind of dark in there, so I thought it was the perfect setting, you know, and we were at the table, and I so eloquently slid my hands across the table and took her hands into mine, and I looked so deeply into her eyes, and I just surrendered myself, and I said, honey, would you like to marry me? Oh, it was so romantic, I still, to this day, yeah, I melt like hot butter, you know, when I think about that.
Well, listen.
All right, Josh, make sure I get that on the wall, please, entire proposal.
Y'all are a cute couple. And, of course, I saw their – I went by and saw them and saw all the dogs. His house is looking great, Randy. Congratulations.
It's going to work.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, is there anything you need that we can help you with?
Roger, I could use some new furniture.
Exactly.
Could use some upgrades in other places. You know,
D. Schuster, if you're listening.
Yes.
Yes, D. Schuster.
Every room has a dog, I think. And then I was sitting there, Roger, at the countertop, and all of a sudden the cat comes up to me, and it was a friendly cat. You know, it was a friend cat. The cat just basically comes up and starts rubbing itself against me. I'm like, okay. All right, usually.
Yeah, that was crack. Crackhead, you never know what that cat
crackhead. You got a cat named Crackhead?
Crackhead is because totally unpredictable. Plus, I guess I better not joke about this. I might get the ITF or whoever may be out here searching my house for drugs. But no, we really this is the most unpredictable cat in the history of mankind. And one minute it can be your best friend, the next minute it'd love to scratch your eyeballs out, it seems like.
We have a guy.
Hey, Crack, I didn't know you was on the radio now, Crack.
Yeah, this is guy at the office that talks like a cat. He's saying hello to you, Randy. The kids love the guy at the office that talks like a cat. Trey, you won't find this on Out of Bounds, I can tell you that right now, or The Zone.
There's got to be an electrical outlet near Roger, better known as Crackhead.
Well, Double R, we just wanted to check in. We got your sweatshirt coming. We love you, man. And we'll be listening to Drive. What do we call Drive Time Sports?
It's Nap Time Sports.
You got us morning madness.
Nap Time Sports. Absolutely. Seriously though, Randy, no, it does help me sometimes.
Nap Time.
It helps me. I can't listen. I'm gonna be honest with you. I can't listen to it when I'm driving. I'm kidding.
the road, that's for sure.
Listen, it's a whole different thing. You've got controversy going on with everybody on your show. Nolan Richardson is one of the best segments on this entire network with you.
So good. Yeah, so good.
That. You're a legend. You obviously do
he's,
what you
he needs
do
to go to the Arkansas
anybody.
Sports Hall of Fame. He needs to be in the Arkansas Sports Hall of Fame.
You sure do. You need to be in there.
He will.
We'll get you some furniture too.
Hey, do your rehab, Randy. Get well, buddy. Get that shoulder well so we can play golf.
Yeah. What?
All right. We love you.
We love you. And thanks, Steve Qualls. Thanks, Steve Qualls, for your hoodie.
Yes, and thanks to Carrie.
I thought you were going to say, Raj, the two words that he had was BS.
BS. No,
brother. You're good to go. You're going to get your sweater. We're going to get a picture of you. But this time, when you take a picture of yourself, would you please have on pants? We can't use the other ones.
What are those? I try not to, unless absolutely necessary, except when I'm proposing.
Thank you, Double
R. See you, buddy. Love you, buddy.
Double R. Randy Ranwater, everybody. Josh, Steve says you want a couple of shirts, too. Can we help you out? Can we come wash?
I talked to Steve.
He just asked me, what size you want?
XL.
Okay, get him a couple of XLs, Steve. We'll do that. You need a Molly maid at your house or something we can help you with?
We've got Trey Cochran in the studio. He's shadowing. Trey, we're going to learn a little bit. How old are you? 12, 13, 14, 16. 15, 16?
16.
Okay, I know I was close.
12.
I don't know. I just started low.
12?
They're big today.
I was a 16-year-old senior in high school. How about that?
So
when I was a sophomore, Josh, I was actually...
That's wild.
I was 13. Yeah, how crazy is that for a little bit?
Because our birthdays are in October, school early.
Yeah. So for a guy like you, are you doing all the social media? Are you on Twitter, Facebook, TikTok, all the things?
Yes, Hinge. I have a YouTube channel.
What is on this YouTube channel?
I do a lot of sports stuff, NFL and March Madness stuff.
You just give a commentary?
Basically, in just analysis videos and just
how about that?
Stuff.
You're a 10th grader. You already have a YouTube channel. You know, yes. Josh. You know, we're talking about Dylan Smith, Wayne's son, and the camps that you can go to. You know, he's been to the camps. Josh has been to camps. Have you been to any broadcasting camps?
Not yet.
That's something, right, Josh?
Would be a good idea. This is boot camp for you right here.
And so, would you like to do radio, TV, or just not know it at this point? Write? You know, nobody talks about being a writer anymore.
Nobody.
But that's out there. Do you write any, or is it mostly just broadcast?
It's just mostly broadcast. I'd like to start out, if I ever have to, with radio.
Yeah.
And then work myself up to TV.
Who are your favorite teams? Who are your favorite teams on the pro level, on the pro sports?
Dallas Cowboys.
Of course. Yes. Okay. All right. What about the basketball?
I'm not a big NBA guy, but baseball. Baseball. Probably like I do like either the Braves or the Cubs. Probably.
What about college football?
College football. It's probably Arkansas, Notre Dame, and Ohio
State.
Let's
say he's Catholic. It's going to be Notre Dame. Yeah. And your dad's been a coach, so you've grown up around football all your life. You're right.
Yes.
Your dad coached it. Has been active before because he was named head coach. He's been an assistant for how many years?
He was about 28, maybe. He was defensive coordinator.
Yeah, about that. So you've grown up around it and love the sport, and you don't play it, but you love the sport.
I do play it.
So you'll be playing for your dad.
Yes.
Wow. Yeah. How's that gonna be?
It'll be interesting.
So did you play on the JV last year?
I did.
You did. Okay. Wow. That's gonna be. Of course, you know we've seen that happen quite a bit, but I've always wondered how
a lot of it is expected of you. You know that.
What position do you play?
Center.
Center. Yeah. All right.
Nice.
Well, listen, Catholic had an unbelievable season. Yes. Got the state championship, really right?
Almost lost to PA.
Yes. Yes. And we mentioned your mom was a teacher as well. So you've grown up
in Bauxite.
Yeah. It's very strict education requirements and I would imagine rules,
yes.
Right? Do you have to study all the time, or do they allow you to have some fun, social time?
Oh, they do. I study whenever I need it and just to get my stuff done.
At age 16, I guess you can drive now, so you have a vehicle to be able to get around and do what you want to do?
Yes, I have to use my parents' front now. But,
okay.
Yeah.
Do you have
So they brought you here?
No, I drove myself.
So at 16, you can drive. You don't have to. 14, I think, is what it used to be, right?
That's a good question.
A licensed driver. Yeah.
Do you have a curfew, like if you go out on the weekends?
It would probably be around... For right now, it's probably around 10, probably.
Right? That's a very good time.
Very good time.
Josh should have that
very
now.
Very good time.
Josh, our producer, should have a 10 o'clock curfew now.
That's
at this
why
point.
He leaves before trivia's over. He has to get home.
That's exactly. Well, listen, man. Well, we
16 years old. Yeah, well, yeah, life's just starting.
Yeah, doing all the good things. Have you ever made anything less than an A?
Before, but I do have a
straight ace. I knew it was coming.
I have a 3.9 right now.
Yeah, so, of course he does. You know, have you taken the ACT or SAT?
Not yet. Okay. I think I'm taking in, probably going to try April.
Listen, you have
you
no,
think you
listen,
could do my taxes?
Listen, Trey, you have no other choice than to make A's in your family. Uh-huh. You have no, your dad's really an do. English teacher who's a football coach, and your mother, what does your mother teach at Bauxite?
Third grade, about everything.
You imagine how smart they are, that family. You're not getting by with anything. You're not getting by with anything. Have you done your homework?
No, sir.
You're an only child. Oh, wow, you're an only child.
It,
oh, yeah. My God.
I'm
an only child, too.
You need to ask your mom and dad to have another kid.
Wow, you got all the focus and pressure. Yeah, my goodness.
It's all on you right now. Yeah. Do you get on Instagram and look up furries?
No. Can people follow you? So you have like a handle that do the same kind of promotional sports stuff like on Twitter?
Yes, I have one on Instagram, a Cowboys Report that's public.
Wow, my goodness.
And a TikTok.
Okay. So we'll put you on the spot. Tell us about the Cowboys, what they've done right now in the offseason.
Well, so far they doesn't seem like they've done much.
Boom, that's it. Yeah. That's it. So, so you're not very impressed so far.
So you go all the way back to what era as a Cowboy fan?
I started 2014.
Roger said this. He has never been able to watch.
He's never seen success.
They've seen success, but not a Super Bowl success.
No, never seen
success. Or close to it.
No.
He hasn't seen anything close to it.
No, the Super Bowl
division
was.
Division round, that's it.
Yeah. Well, Trey, that's great. Well, nice to meet you,
yes,
buddy.
Yeah.
We will follow your career. You can come in and hang out when you want to.
I'd love to have you.
Yes. We'll take you out on the town sometime when you get over 18.
Yeah.
Or 21, whichever.
Yeah.
Tell your dad.
Right now, we'll give you a non-alcoholic Jello shot.
Yes. My YouTube channel is called
TreyDog60.
TreyDog60.
Any reason for that?
I kind of just thought of it, and I was like, younger, and then I was like, that's going to be my YouTube channel name.
Okay, well, listen, when you got a name like Trey, it is Trey Dog.
Well,
you
got Trey Dog, and then it's just 60.
Well, yeah. Trey's got your real, what's your name? What's your first name?
Well, my real name is Richard.
Right, Richard.
Yes.
Okay, yeah.
Do you wear number 60, I would presume?
I am 65. I do wear 65.
Got to change it.
You got to
have a theme there.
I would, but I think it got taken, I think, so, yeah.
All right, that is the one and only Trey Cochran. Be watching him in years to come. Thanks, Trey. All right, we'll take a break and be back just a minute.
Registration is open for the 2024 1037 The Buzz Spring Golf Tournament, Monday, April 15th at the Burns Park Golf Course, presented by Tito's Handmade Vodka.
This is SportsCenter.
Last night in the first game of the first four in Dayton, Wagner won their first tournament game in program history, beating Howard 71-68. The Seahawks will now move on to face the West top seed Tar Heels on Thursday. In the second game, Colorado State dominated Virginia, winning 67-42 behind Neat Clifford's 17 points, 10 rebounds, and 6 assists. The Cavaliers had a disgusting showing on offense, shooting 25% from the floor and 18% from 3. The 10-seeded Rams will move on to face the 7th-seeded Longhorns of Texas on Thursday. Tonight in Dayton, 16 seeds Grambling and Montana State will go at it at 5:40. The winner will face Purdue on Friday, and in the second game, 10 seeds Colorado and Boise State will face off at 8:10. The winner will face Florida on Friday. Both games can be seen on True TV. I'm Christian Weaver with the Buzz Radio Network.
Weather from the Fletcher Weather Center with Channel 7's Melinda Mayo.
Continuing to warm up across Arkansas, 75 today, mostly sunny. Could be a couple of showers or thunderstorms in North Arkansas, and tonight's low drops down to 50. Better rain chances statewide arriving for Thursday. From the Channel 7 Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Melinda Mayo.
Fletcher Dodge wants to buy your car. We'll buy any make or model, and we'll pay you more than anyone else. Please, turn your old car into cash at Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood.
We're with Bridget, whose husband won't be home for months, and whose daughter is due any day. We're with Mike, who's leaving home to protect his family and yours. We're with all service members and their families. who need community, connection, and maybe a bit of magic. Are you with them? Learn more at USO.org today.
Hello there, homeowner. Roger Scott for Leaf Guard Gutters of Arkansas. Are you tired of dealing with clogged gutters, climbing ladders, and worrying about potential damage to your home? Well, listen up to me now. Leaf Guard of Arkansas's got you covered. Introducing Leaf Guard, the only true one-piece seamless covered gutter system on the market guaranteed to never, ever clog. With Leaf Guard, you can kiss goodbye to all the hassle of climbing up and cleaning out all that muck and mud and shingle grit. No more hiring someone else to do it, or worse yet, risking serious damage and issues by doing nothing at all. Spring is finally here, which means it's time for Leaf Guard's famous Ugly Gutter event. Leaf Guard will swoop in, take down, and haul away all those unsightly gutters at absolutely no charge, and you'll receive an incredible 60% off installation on a whole house Leaf Guard gutter system. But wait, there's more. Ask about the 0% financing options and additional discounts for seniors and military personnel. Do not let ugly gutters ruin your home's curb appeal or cause costly damage. Call 501-664-5400 or visit leafguardandmore.com to schedule your free estimate today. Leaf Guard of Arkansas, protecting your home one seamless gutter at a time.
Smith & Wesson revolvers are built to suit the demands of the most serious firearms enthusiast. And for a limited time at Max Prairie Wings in Stuttgart, receive a $50 rebate on Smith & Wesson J-frame revolvers or a $75 rebate on Smith & Wesson K-frame, L-frame, N-frame, and Governor revolvers. This offer expires April 30th, so hurry before time runs out. Max Prairie Wings, with the best selection, the most competitive prices, and all the ammo you need. So make the short drive to Stuttgart today or online at maxpw.com.
Roger Scott for Gravely Mowers. You know, when it comes to beautiful lawns, nothing cuts like a Gravely. And when it comes to cutting prices, there's nothing like the Gravely Mow the Distance sales event, where you can save up to 25%. And special financing is available on America's most rugged and dependable mowers, including their ZT-HD. It's the residential mower built to commercial standards. But hurry, because the Mow the Distance sale is only through April 8th and only at your authorized Gravely dealers like Dacus Rental in Searcy or Haynes Home Center in Morrilton.
Let me tell you about my friends, Carl and Karen.
This place is sus. Let's go to Tunica.
And so they did. And immediately, they became winners.
Hey, baby, what you doing?
Winning. Hey, baby, what you doing?
Winning.
And not just gaming, either. They did spa.
Winning. Dancing.
Winning.
Or at the sportsbook.
Winning.
Or enjoying a world-renowned meal.
Winning.
No matter what you're doing in Tunica, you're always a winner. Learn more at tunicatravel.com.
Welcome back to Morning Mayhem, live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios. Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
I've heard that quite a bit.
Yeah, what,
quite a bit. Sorry. I don't know what I said.
Get that.
Get that.
Yes, I find joy in your stumbles whenever I can.
Sandra Eccles.
Hey, guys. You know, Roger always talks about his gang, the Hobson Street Hobos. But what he doesn't mention is that I'm the reason he had to join a gang. We didn't have to be worried about taking another ass with him.
Josh, where's your girlfriend? You bring your girlfriend in. Pick a color. Josh?
Hello, Leslie.
Let the boy watch.
Good morning, ma'am.
Here, press it. Not here, but they're still sure to use me in the promotional material.
Josh's parents.
Asking you, Shivers.
Hey, Josh, your mother and I are up at Cape Cod counting our money and eating lobster tails. Are you still in radio?
It's Nashville Grand Hyatt. Hello.
Paging Karen Basil, your room is ready. Karen Basil.
Karen
that was
Basil.
So good.
That was good.
A little
stuff.
Bit of a Roger's Vault. I think we're going to make that a bit. Going through Roger's Vault. If you want to be a sponsor of that, call us. That'll be fun. Yeah. A lot of great material in there. Today, there's a couple birthdays I haven't gotten to. I'm going to a great song right here. Josh, I'm going to you on this. 1945, Pat Riley's birthday today. Now, this is what I have right here. The Lakers and the Knicks. Where else? Is that the two places he's coached anywhere else?
Miami.
Miami.
He won a championship in Miami.
Yeah. So this says, what is unique about Pat Riley in terms of his coaching history?
He has won a championship with three separate teams.
If that's the case, I don't
did
have that listed.
Did he win one with the
Knicks?
Well, he didn't win. No, he didn't. No, I didn't show you. He won two different places, which is hard to – not many have done that, right?
Did he win a national title at Kentucky? No, as a college guy.
Let's
as a player.
By the way, who
– I think that was a Texas Western beat them, didn't they? I think – isn't that the one with – yeah.
How many coaches have won two NBA titles with two different teams? That's a short list, I would imagine.
Did the cat that coached LeBron? What's his name?
Phil Jackson has.
Phil did.
Where did he get the other one?
L.A. and
oh, I forgot that he went to the Lakers. Yeah. I completely forgot about that. Oh my gosh!
What about what's his name? What was the guy's name that was LeBron's buddy?
Mike Brown.
No.
So this is what I have here. So I have Pat Riley as the highest. He's the coach with the highest winning percentage in basketball history.
It's not surprising.
Yeah, 719.
Also, two-time NBA, he's been NBA Executive of the Year. So.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Also, a couple other birthdays I want to mention. William Hurt, Roger, when you think of him, what do you think of?
You know what? The thing that pops into my mind now is he played the alter ego of Kevin Costner in that really wild movie what was the name of the one? Mr. Something. Kevin Costner played a Mr. Something.
I see.
Where
he was a killer.
He was a killer, and his alter ego was in the, you know, it was in the back seat in the mirror and all those.
Academy Award winning actor. I think that's Kiss of the Spider one, which I have not seen. Broadcast News.
Broadcast News, and then I think he was in Body Heat, too.
Oh, he was in Body Heat. That's where I think I know him. Altered States, I remember that was a weird movie. The Big Chill.
He was in Michael. I mean, he was in Michael with John Travolta. He played one of the guys in that one. I'm trying to think, what was it?
The Big Chill? What you remember in The Big Chill?
He was Big Chill and Heat. Those were big, or 9.5 weeks, whatever you say.
Spike Lee's birthday today. When you think of Spike Lee, what do you think of, Rod? You think Do the Right Thing, Mo Better Blues, Jungle Fever?
Those movies,
Black Klansman. Now, you know, I haven't seen Black Klansman. They say that's so really, really good.
It's
true story. Yes.
Yeah. Denzel's boy plays in it, but I don't.
I tell you the one. Let me tell you the movie that I thought was
Do the Right Thing.
Do the Right Thing, but I'm telling you, she's got to have it. Malcolm X. I read the book Malcolm X, and Denzel Washington. I think maybe it's his greatest role ever because you're playing a real person.
Yeah, he plays a role, and he plays a shorty in that movie.
Also, he got game.
What? I thought he was Malcolm X.
No, Denzel was. No, I'm talking about.
He's talking about Spike. Spike. Yeah, but
yeah,
Denzel was so
shorty.
Good in
he
that.
Plays
yeah,
shorty. Yeah, plays one of his buddies that he sees in church.
All right, so let me throw another name at you. And apparently, she starred with William Hurt, Holly Hunter. When you think of Holly Hunter, what do you think of?
I see her. I don't know.
There's got to be a movie that I recognize her from. Oh, I know she was in the DC Superman movie where she gets killed as but that's not the one anybody
Holly
thinks
Hunt
of.
Does?
Holly Hunter.
Holly Hunter.
Holly Hunter. That's not the one most people.
She was in The Firm.
She was in The Firm. She was in Broadcast News. She was in Raising Arizona, Roger, and you always say.
Yeah, that's right.
Don't you say Raising Arizona is one of the great movies?
Oh, I love Raising Arizona.
Acres Yelling, Raising Arizona.
Yeah, I love Raising Arizona.
They didn't win Best Picture.
It didn't win Best Picture.
Is Nicolas Cage in that, too?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he was H.I. McDonough.
You know, in The Firm, and I think The Piano, obviously, she was there. So what, I can't remember what role she played in The Firm. Oh, she was his assistant.
In The Firm.
She was his assistant, right?
She was,
right? Yeah.
Who's the guy? Not, who's assistant?
She was Tom Cruise's assistant.
No, she was.
She was helping him. Wasn't she helping him?
She was, what's his name, assistant? Who's Crazy Eye that played Mr. Jericho in Lethal Weapon?
Yeah.
He played Buddy Holly. What's that actor's
name? Worked for him.
Yeah.
She worked for him.
Yeah.
What was his role in that? I can't remember.
He was an attorney.
I know, but I can't remember the.
She's under his desk when the bad guys come in and shoot him. What's
that's
his
right.
Name? What's
now,
his name?
Now, what is a Tom Cruise movie that was shot over in Memphis? I'm getting my Grisham movies.
It might be the same
is
one.
Is it the same one?
Yeah.
Yeah, she was very good. She was also a Roger. Here we go. I'm going to give this one to you.
I'm thinking of Tyronn Lue. Tyronn Lue.
Lue.
Yeah, didn't he win? Did he win somewhere else with LeBron?
No, not.
I thought
coach.
He won two. Anyway, go ahead.
What if I said this? This is a movie we both love, and I forgot she had a role in this. And she was telling her husband, her ex-husband, that this guy, this new guy that I have, he's this. And I'm blanking on the word. I'm leading you down the path. It was George Clooney.
I can't take it.
Yeah, he's getting mad.
For God's sakes, gentlemen. Gary Busey.
Thank you.
It is The Firm that they filmed in Memphis.
Yes.
Yeah, Holly Hunter. And he was not an attorney. He was a private investigator.
Private investigator.
Okay,
what was her role, though? How did she connect with
Cruise? His assistant, and then they worked together to bust the firm.
Okay.
After they killed her guy. So they had a mutual interest in busting the firm because he obviously was against them. She was against them because they killed her guy.
Gotcha.
And then she fell in love with his brother, Ray, you remember?
With Tom Cruise's brother, yes.
Tom Cruise's brother,
so,
Ray.
So she was helping Tom Cruise in this thing. That's
he's such a good actor, Ray, the guy that plays Ray.
He is a good actor. I was thinking about him. Who is it? What else has he been in? Let's just get down another wormhole.
He was the abusive husband in another Stephen King movie, not Misery. What was the one where he fell in the... Fell in a well. The eclipse was there.
I know what you're talking about, but I didn't see it.
Dad, go. Yeah, he plays a good one.
Okay, you're gonna help me get this.
Maybe not. Where are we at on this? Come on.
Holly Hunter and there's a scene, and I'm just kidding. You know what it is now.
Come on, let's go.
Oh, brother, where art thou? Where Clooney's in there.
Oh, absolutely.
She's describing the term.
Right.
What is it?
He's a suitor. Yeah.
Remember, because Clooney's in there.
Ray McKinnon.
Ray McKinnon, who is right. Marquez. He was in there.
So
he's
long to get
here. He's a suitor.
He's a suitor. He's bona fide.
Bonafide, that's what it is. Thank you, Justin. Very good. Good job, Roger.
Thank you, Justin, for coming in. He just killed it.
You know how when Baz is like, come on.
I'm looking at, she's been in a lot of movies.
Another one she's in with Richard Dreyfuss where she plays,
Always.
That's it. That's a good one. I like that one. It's sentimental. I'm more of a sentimental guy. They were raised in Arizona, of course, where she said, we need a baby, huh?
All right,
go up and get me a baby.
I expect, Roger, you to get this one. Kathy Ireland's birthday today.
Do you breastfeed Miss McDonough? You're pretty capable.
When you think of Kathy Ireland, what is the movie that comes to mind?
Well, there's a couple of home movies into my head
that I think about.
Kathy Ireland, didn't she play?
She actually was in a lot of movies. She's a model.
Movie.
Yes, come on. N-R.
N-R. N-R. Irreplaceable.
Roughness. Black roughness.
Indecent roughness.
No, necessary roughness.
Innecessary. I'm sorry.
Last but not least, Michael Rapaport, who now has become a very outspoken...
Yeah, weird. Oh, he's been all over the place. The only movie that I know him in...
True Romance.
No.
Is it True Romance? Okay.
The only movie that I know him in is he plays in the movie Copland.
He is in Copland.
Yeah, I see him in Copland.
I can only hope that that people like are doing just like Justin driving around in their cars, Roger. They're going, you idiots!
You should have heard him. I can hear him in his office. He goes, Josh, Raising Arizona.
David Stratham. And the name of the movie, Mr. Brooks is the costume.
Oh, Mr. Brooks,
thank you.
Yes, yes.
I love that. When somebody...
Oh, what, you won the Academy Award for piano. I've not seen that.
Yeah, tell me the name of the movie with Stratham. Who was the actress that won the Academy Award? She was in Misery. Who was the one in Misery?
Oh, yes.
Kathy Bates, yes. So Kathy Bates is in the movie. She's abused by Stratham.
What movie is this?
Also abused. That's what I'm trying to find out. And Stratham abuses his daughter. It's terrible.
So Trey, this is what we do on our show.
I used to have all this horrible information.
The next show that comes on has all the answers. We don't. And we like to throw it out there and have people.
We like to find our way. Finding our way. Anchory came in and corrected three details in a matter of 10 seconds. He's like, here's the movie.
It takes all the fun out of it for listeners to scream or email or text us to go, you idiots.
If you put a microphone, if you put that, a magnifying glass on the emoji where the head blows up, it's Justin Aker. It looks just like him because his head explodes.
Or Jason Statham?
Is it David Stratham?
It's Stratherin.
Somebody put Tokyo Drift.
Jason Statham is the transporter.
No, I said David.
Yeah, David's what they put here on here. David Stratham.
Yeah, different guy.
Yeah,
that's what I said.
Yeah.
What I say?
Somebody thought you meant Jason Statham.
No, not Jason.
Do you think Holly Hunter's a cutie, Raj?
There's a quality about her. Yeah, I find her attractive.
Yeah, there's.
I find her attractive.
I love her.
You know what?
I find her attractive
in a way, like I find the chick only in a certain movie, like the lady that played Costner's wife in Field of Dreams.
Yeah.
What's her name?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I think she's a poor man's Holly Hunter. Look her up.
What we did there, we just threw out 30 questions in a 5-minute
period. Answered maybe two of them. By the way, did you all, speaking of movies, did you all see that Heat 2?
No. Yes. No.
Well, Austin, your boy Austin Butler is gonna is apparently supposed to be Val Kilmer.
They don't need to. They
Austin
don't need to do
Butler is playing the Val Kilmer.
They're not remaking
or
it.
Or will he play Val Kilmer?
Prequel?
Yes.
Okay.
I think it's kind of how they got, the gang together.
Can I tell you? I was not blown away by Heat.
You are wrong.
I was not blown away by Heat.
How are you not?
It just I don't know why.
Well, the slow part was the relationship with Pacino and his wife and all that that was going on.
Yeah,
that was too monotonous for me.
De Niro's girl didn't really do a whole lot for me either. The girl who was he met at the
No. But he walked away from her, and the thing was he just couldn't let it go.
He couldn't let it go.
That was the deal.
He had
that
to
right
kill
there.
Wayne Grove.
He had to do it. He had to kill Wayngro.
Yeah, I wonder if Wayngro will be back in the Heat and Heat 2.
It can't be.
We'll come back and wrap things up. Yeah, it's a prequel. Yeah. We appreciate you listening to us and knowing that we're not going to get it right every time. That's why we need you. That's why we need you.
That's why we need you on the Southern Structure Solutions text line.
Or
thank you.
Yes.
To what did it call?
No, it's the Oracle.
Call the 501 Dolores Claiborne. Dolores Claiborne is the movie.
Yes.
It's a good it's an excellent movie. A little disturbing. But anytime it's on, if I catch
that's
it,
that's what Kathy Bates beating up James Caan.
No, that's Kathy Bates is who I was looking for. She's with David Stratham.
Oh, and the Dolores Claiborne.
Yeah, and the Dolores Claiborne. It's
a
really
I think
good movie.
We got as many wrong, we guessed as many times wrong as we guessed them right.
But here's the thing. That's
why. That's right, Trey. Don't be ashamed of that.
Don't be ashamed
of that. People don't mind
well,
it.
Wait a second.
They want to help you.
But the very best batter is only over 400.
Thank you, Roger. That's a way to go right to the meat of the heart of the matter there. Thank you. All right, we'll come back right. Things up 948. Lovely witch, give me a little charm that'll make me rich. Give me $1 million and tell you what I'll do. This very night, I'm gonna marry you, and it'll be another man done gone. Nothing compares to the feeling of wearing a Facets of Fire diamond from Sissy's Log Cabin. The first diamond cutting advancement in over a century, Facets of Fire diamonds are created by etching thousands of nanoprisms onto the pavilion of an exquisite natural diamond. The result is a stone with more brilliance than any other. Just ask any of the expert staff at Sissy's and they'll show you the vibrant burst of fiery color that's visible to the naked eye. From engagement rings to necklaces to bracelets to earrings, a Facets of Fire diamond takes any piece to a new level of spectacular, and no jewelry collection is complete without one. Facets of Fire diamonds are passion personified, but don't just take my word for it. You can shop Facets of Fire online at sissyslogcabin.com or at any of their 6 locations. Experience the revolution in diamonds for yourself only at Sissy's Log Cabin, because life's too short for ordinary jewelry.
What do you do when the power goes out? Well, now you can do anything you want when you purchase a Generac home standby generator from Generator Supercenter of Little Rock. Come visit the experts at Central Arkansas's only generator showroom located on Chenal Parkway in West Little Rock. We offer a turnkey solution, financing, and 24/7 service. Visit our website for more info at GeneratorSupercenterOfLittleRock.com. The standby power people.
Hello, Buzz listeners. This is Chris Zender with Fletcher Dodge, and I want to help you lower your car payment. Let us show you how you can trade in your old car for a brand new Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, or Ram with a lower car payment. We've got 0% financing on new Rams, or you can take up to $12,000 off the sticker. It's your choice. We also have 0% financing on new Chrysler Pacificas and $10,000 plus discounts on new Jeep Gladiators. Or how about a new Dodge Charger or Challenger for $5,000 off? We've got lots of inventory to choose from. Just pick one out and tell us how much you want to pay. We'll do the rest. Don't worry about your credit. If other dealers have told you no, come see us and let us help you get a new or pre-owned dependable vehicle. Go to FletcherDeals.com and simply click Apply for Financing and we'll do the rest. At Fletcher Dodge, you always get the best price, the lowest finance rate, and more for your trade. And also a hassle-free buying experience. Shop Fletcher Dodge in Sherwood before you buy anywhere else. Come see us in person at Fletcher Dodge on Warden Road in Sherwood or shop online at FletcherDeals.com.
The Avett Brothers are coming to Little Rock September 17th at First Security Amphitheater. Tickets are on sale Friday at 10 a.m. at Ticketmaster.com. I got requests. Make plans now for an evening with the Avett Brothers, September 17th at First Security Amphitheater. Get tickets this Friday.
You've heard about the thousands of patients finally getting relief from chronic joint pain thanks to QC Kinetics non-invasive treatments. And here's one who was determined to avoid surgery. Meet Vicky.
The orthopedic surgeon said, well, you're going to need knee replacement sooner rather than later. I kept hearing commercials about QC Kinetics and thought, well, I'm going to check them out first.
QC Kinetics has treated over 20,000 patients like Vicky around the country. People who were told they needed surgery but chose a more natural, less invasive approach that uses regenerative treatments to help heal and restore painful joints with no downtime.
If QC Kinetics had not been what I expected, I would have gone through with the surgery, but I got so much relief, am now pretty much pain-free that I don't have to have the surgery.
Before going under the knife, you need to check out QC Kinetics. The consultation is free. Call today.
Call QC Kinetics, 501-222-8440. That's 501-222-8440. 501-222-8440.
Hey there, Arkansas. It's Rowdy Hog Pickleball calling. Are you ready to join in the fun? Discover why pickleball is the fastest growing sport in America. It's an absolute blast for the whole family. Rowdy Hog Pickleball has equipment for all budgets. And here's the best part. Indoor courts are coming soon. And membership is free. Don't miss out on the action. Conveniently located in the outlets of Little Rock. And visit RowdyHogPickleball.com for your free membership.
What's going on, everyone? DJ Williams here with The Buzz, and man, we got a jam-packed show for you. Joe Klein is going to be in studio. Very excited to have Joe in, talk about NCAA tournament as March Madness is upon us. And Hagen Smith, thanks to our friends at Stifel Financial, is going to be on. This guy, man, it's like he just can't miss. Also, big thanks to Little Rock Athletic Club for sponsoring our segment with Kevin Kelly. It's always fun having Joe and Kevin in at the same time. And Neil Earthman is going to be with us from the NCAA. There's a lot of wrestling to talk about. It starts at 10 a.m., the Zone, where sports and entertainment come crashing together.
Always make sure to say please and thank you. Morning Mayhem is back on the air, live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios, Oaklawn, Arkansas's only racing casino resort.
It's Roger here. Shotgun shots goes sleaze, not sleaze.
The P is missing.
Really, is it in there really?
It is. It's not as clear as I want.
Can we hear it? Let's see.
Morning drive will never be the same with Morning Mayhem on the radio, live from the Oaklawn Hot Springs Studios, Oaklawn, right. Arkansas's. Let's keep the good vibes going. Morning Mayhem is back on the air, live.
No, it doesn't say it.
Yeah, so whatever that clip is, he says sleaze instead of spleaze.
Yeah, he might have, because he wouldn't think there's a word named spleaze. Let's see. He's got it right there. Amy Madigan.
Go ahead.
Not this one for some reason. I don't know.
Amy Madigan is who's the actress that played Costner's wife in Field of Dreams. And I think she's...
Oh, yeah, I recognize her. Yeah, she's been around.
Oh, she's been around a while.
Oh, you know who she's married to?
Yeah, Ed Harris.
40 years.
Ed Harris.
Tomorrow, Roger will be back in studio. Tomorrow, we'll have Will McIntyre for the first time.
Looking forward to that. He's a Central Arkansas boy.
Yeah. Tommy Smith tomorrow.
What Tommy Smith will be here Thursday. Who else do we have on Thursday?
Big Joe Klein will be with
Big
us tomorrow.
Big Joe Klein. It'll be the...
We got Factor Crap tomorrow. Factor Crap returns tomorrow.
We haven't done the feud yet.
We missed that. We got to do that tomorrow too.
Was the feud usually a Wednesday?
Tuesday.
We didn't do because Chuck's out of town.
We were at the zoo.
We were at the zoo yesterday. Chuck's having
big opportunity for Baz and I to win another one because JM's gone.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, wow.
I would love to win when JM's not here too. Justin will be checking in here with us shortly. 661-1037. We appreciate everybody texting us today. It's been a fun day. A lot of things we covered, Roger. We learned about, remember what bibliomania is?
I do, Booker. It's a book, book man, book reader.
It's, yeah, it's those who are obsessed with books. We learned that today. And also, don't forget, Won't You Be My Neighbor Day today. That
Fred was, Rogers.
Yes.
Didn't watch a lot of that growing up. Watch Electric Company. That was my number one AET and PBS show was The Electric Company, the first time I ever saw Morgan Freeman.
The other thing, the two things we didn't get a chance to mention, today is the anniversary of Eric Clapton's four-year-old son falling from the 53rd floor of their New York apartment. He wrote Tears in Heaven as a tribute. I mean,
when you hear that song and you think about that, I can't.
I don't know how that works. I don't know how a baby, I don't remember the story on how the baby was able to get out on the ledge.
Well, a little four-year-old can fit through a balcony easily. Yeah.
The other thing, Roger, you and I were surprised about, that this is is 28 years ago today that Lyle and Eric Menendez were convicted of first-degree murder for killed both their mother and father.
You know, that was one of the first times I've ever seen anybody that actually started thinking about marrying people in prison for the rest of their life. So they were having chicks falling in love with them and all that.
I think it's still happening.
Who's that? Yeah. Oh, it does still
They're
happen.
They're still in jail. But that was a vicious murder. Didn't they almost get out of it?
I don't think they almost got out. I think they were always in.
They're both in prison, though. They have not gotten out.
Yeah.
I thought they had it coming.
Yeah, they did.
Parents had it coming.
Oh, yeah. That's
Yusuf.
That's what they portray.
That's exactly.
I think they're misunderstood, Roger.
They were, especially since he wore his dad's shoes. You never fit into them.
Oh,
Justin, what's happening on the zone today?
Great day today. I'm excited. Hagen Smith, thanks to Stiefel Financial at 10:30 today. Got screwed out of another player of the week this week. I mean, that's just the way it's going to be. He's too great. He's Michael Jordan now. So it's like, okay, well, listen, if you don't strike out 20 guys, we don't care anymore. Sucks. But anyway, he's too good for everybody else. Kevin Kelly again, thanks to Little Rock Athletic Club. Neil Erzman's going to join us. They're at the NCAAs. He's got a handful of wrestlers who are competing in the national championships this week. Yes. And we will talk to him about it. And then we've also got Air Lee coming up from Eat My Catfish. So if you guys want to swing back through around 12:30.
You want to swing back through and get some food.
Might get a little lunch. Because Joe has abandoned us today. I'm like, well, we didn't want to talk basketball anyway. There's nothing going on.
He just abandoned
Knucklehead. He had to drive his grandkids back home, apparently.
Well, you know, as you can tell on this station, we have plenty of folks that want to be a part of these shows.
Probably too many in many cases. But that's okay.
Yes, and so did you hear Rogers describe your emoji? The emoji music there, Roger.
Was it poop?
No, it's the head exploding.
When you listen to this show.
Just like Hagen Smith, you're going to have to go above the to get me. I just expect it. You're going to have to really do something dumb for me to be shocked.
I love it when he can't stand anymore. He finally starts screaming.
You know,
Josh!
Because he's in there.
Thank y'all for listening.
Thank you. We had a great time. Thank you.